But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Let me go right to Ryan, who's been sitting there on the phone for about a half hour. Ryan, what do you got for the show?
Cole fucking K.
Cole fucking K. Cole fucking K.
Enjoy your vacation.
Thank you, Ryan.
Yeah.
Brad in South Carolina.
Can I hear Danny's thing again?
Cole fucking K!
Yeah, good voice, Danny.
That's a good one.
Cole fucking K!
That just brings fucking excitement to the show.
Man. Really does.
That's a great voice.
Well, what's great is these guys have been sitting on hold just to say that.
Just to say Cole fucking Kane. By the way, why is my Gatorade always piss warm? It's just piss warm. I want cold Gatorade.
Attaboy.
I'm fancy. I want a cup with ice in it now.
Quickly for the boss.
Cold Gatorade. Cold Gatorade.
It's ridiculous. Every day I haven't said a word. I figured, one day maybe it'll be cold.
You got a bitch. You get a lot done when you bitch.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And then everyone thinks you're an asshole. That's the other side of it. But
I don't care.
But you still get a lot done.
The last thing I care about is what anyone fucking thinks.
Well, this guy's on the phone, too.
Asshole.
What's your name, sir? It doesn't have your name.
Dave.
Hey, Dave, what do you got?
I just wanted to find out what you thought of Michael Vick signing with the Eagles.
Well, that's a very good question because there's a lot of people that are upset that Michael Vick is playing football.
Absolutely.
I think you're listening to a radio show where we know everything because we told you guys that Michael Vick would have to sign with a dirty team, an ugly team, not a nice team, and the Eagles are perfect for Michael Vick, a two-year deal for Michael Vick.
I was thinking Raiders because that is just a nasty, ugly team.
Oh, yeah, they're gangbangers out there.
But the Eagles, they're an ugly team. They got ugly fans. They're just nasty. He fits right in.
A lot of people on Twitter, they're like, you know, they'll never forgive Michael Vick because of what he did.
Yeah.
I don't give a shit what Michael Vick did.
Who cares?
I mean, when Vick sucks, so does the Eagles. Go Giants.
Go Giants. Well, go Jets, you motherfucker.
Fuck you, go Giants.
Go fuck yourself.
Wow, anger.
You're going to have to agree to disagree. Don't see that one being resolved anytime soon.
That never works.
No, I don't know. I mean, what he did with the dogs was completely disgusting, obviously.
Thank you.
I guess he did his time, so he should be able to play.
Absolutely.
Don't do the crime if you can't do the time.
Yeah, I don't believe there's actual morals in sports. They try to throw morals at us, but it's bullshit. It's a facade.
And once you go to jail, you know what I mean? It's like what he did was terrible, but once you go to fucking prison for it, it's like you're done. You went to prison, it's done.
Yeah.
You got to get the guy make a living.
Also, there are people that are, you know, convicted of things like manslaughter and things like that. And they play and no one gives a shit.
Who's that lineman in the NFL who was convicted?
Dante?
No.
Dante Stallworth got suspended for the year.
It wasn't for drugs. It was a guy who stole a felt hat. I forget who that was. He plays
wrecking our sports discussion with a felt hat reference.
Jimmy has a hat fetish.
Who doesn't?
There's something about hats with Jimmy.
He stole it. Was in his pocket, and they searched him at the airport.
On a hat.
It's a two-year deal, not a one-year deal, I believe, right?
Not the one-year deal.
It's a one-year deal?
With an option for two.
That crap. Uh-oh. That's 2 years, trust me.
It better be good.
Trust me, that option, whatever, don't get me started. Dante Stallworth out the entire season because of his DWI manslaughter conviction. So.
Jesus.
But Michael Vick gets to play for the Eagles. That's a strong move by the Eagles.
But there's never any real outrage when somebody comes back from, like, manslaughter.
Yeah.
Things like that. Because people, I guess, care more about little puppies.
Yeah.
Than people.
Yeah. So, but when that hit the wire, people went, holy shit.
Yeah, that
holy
was
shit.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, he went to jail. Fuck it. What are you gonna do? Keep the guy from making his livelihood?
I think it'll be fun to watch as he plays some of these teams. they're gonna come out of the woodwork screaming and yelling at Michael Vick.
Who let the dogs out? I'm playing that.
We get it.
I bet you the Browns really wanted him, but they're like, there's no way we could do this.
We can't. We'd have to change the little mascot.
We can't have the dog pound anymore. We can't have Michael Vick on our team if we have something called the dog pound. This guy is saying Jimmy James from PA.
Hey, morning, boys.
Hey, Jimmy.
Hey, you got a feel for McNabb because Philly is going to be in turmoil. They begged for McNabb to be pulled all year last year when they had some no-name shitbag as a backup quarterback because those fans just never appreciated him. And now they have Vic sitting on the bench. There's just going to be turmoil. They're going to be begging for Vic all year. McNabb just can't win in that goddamn town.
Yeah, it'll be interesting. But, Michael Vic, they're not even attempting to play him at quarterback. I mean, they could do the old switcheroo, I'm sure, later on in the season. But yeah.
They're saying that now, but you know as soon as they lose two games in a row,
they're putting him in.
Falling for McNabb's head.
Good point. I like how you said there'll be turmoil in Philly. It's Friday. There's turmoil in Philly, okay?
It doesn't matter.
What are you, nuts?
It's a fucking place.
fucking Philly for the UFC 101. Oh, my God. Every time there's a black fighter versus a white fighter, it was so ridiculously racist.
Of course.
They were booing the black guy, cheering on the white guy. Although Silva did turn him around because he got booed like crazy, and when he knocked out Forrest Griffin, they did cheer for Silva by the end of that fight. Thank you, Jimmy. Go ahead. Go ahead. I thought you were done. I'm sorry.
I was just going to say at the end of that fight that Silva take the mic and say, "Am I going to change?
If we could change,
touch it up,
then maybe the whole world would change."
That's stupid.
Oh, God.
Fucking
Rocky,
speech.
Rocky, Rocky, Rocky.
They're all chanting for Rocky, and then that guy that had a career because he looked like Gorbachev.
Yeah.
That actor that played Gorby in every fucking bad movie.
Dude, my fucking back is tingling right now remembering that scene.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
What we saw tonight was a change. And if we could change here, maybe the whole world could
shut up. I hope your fucking stupid wife drops another load on the pet floor,
exactly.
Pet shop floor.
Hope she falls on the feed while Butt just fucks her face.
Can we get...
Cuff and Link.
We got to get that speech
on each
now.
Nipple. He used Cuff and Link as nipple clips.
Yeah.
His little turtles.
When Adrian would fall asleep, they would bite her nipples like little alligator clamps. She would wake up crying.
We got to get that speech now. Let's say hi to Bill in Arizona.
Find that stupid speech.
Bill!
Look at Danny Rules.
Hold on a second. I can't go both places.
Hello, Bill!
Bill, what's up?
Hello. Seriously, I don't know why anybody really gives a flying fuck whether Michael Vick's playing football or underwater fucking basket weaving.
Ooh.
The fact of the matter is, we're the only country in the goddamn world that treats dogs like they're part of the fucking family.
Asia
eats them, and Europe fucking uses them as tools. I mean,
you're right.
Kill a fucking human.
Guys, right.
Bullshit.
This country is weird, man. Our priorities are weird. I don't know. Maybe faggy France. But stupid England. What other countries treat dogs as well as we do? And I know there's plenty of fucking dogs running around that are emaciated and treated like shit and put in dog fighting and everything. But when you think about it, people treat dogs like part of the family. They have a house.
I would bet there's more dogs in this country that are treated like shit, by the way. It's a perception.
Oh, I think you're right.
I think there's a ton of dogs out there that are being treated like
Oh, I think you're right.
Like shit.
I'm just saying that when people have dogs, they treat them like part of the family. They have steady eats. They got a roof over their head, companionship. They're played with and everything. It's just a weird thing.
I don't think that's weird. I think that's fine. I think where the weird thing is that we actually we care about dogs more than our fellow human beings.
Mm-hmm.
When you see a horrible dog story, it bothers you more than a horrible human story in a lot of cases.
Well, look at movies. Just look at them. That's what I'm just saying.
They really are
during
magic.
Vacation. Just go to a movie. No, look at movies. They usually animal or dog deaths in movies test very poorly in movies, and they usually show the dog didn't die or some weird twist.
Yeah, it pops up at the end.
But there could be just a body count that's immeasurable. And that's fine.
Dogs are probably seen like kids. In the way that they're innocent.
Yes, retarded children, I believe.
But I think
One of the biggest cop-outs was in, what was the movie with the divorce there? Michael Douglas was in
War of the Roses?
War of the Roses, thank you.
There was a dog in that movie?
War of the Roses, yeah. And the wife made like she cooked the guy's dog and fed it to him. And it was like one of those holy shit moments where... Oh, my God, that is as far as you can go in hating another human being.
Sure, sure.
And then they had to show the dog pop its head up out of the bushes like it didn't really happen. Because initially they had run it that way in front of a test audience, and the audience, like, they couldn't handle it. They could not fucking handle the fact that she cooked his dog. Right.
You know what's so weird about that? Like, it doesn't happen either way. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, if they're filming a movie, they're not actually feeding
a dog
to an actor.
But the story, they can't handle the story.
But they can't handle the story.
Yeah.
But you should be able to do whatever the fuck you want in movies because you're not really doing it.
Yeah.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah.
Like, they never did fed the dog to the guy.
No.
But they had to show the dog popping up anyway in the yard to prove, see, this acting dog is still alive.
Doggy actor's still okay.
So stupid.
You know how many things have been ruined? Like Oedipus mentioned with BCN focus groups. Fucking focus groups ruin everything. Let the artist or the director, whatever they see is what it should be, they're the creative ones. Let them do it.
Yeah, there's just got to be another outlet for that type of stuff. That's all.
Mm. Oh, because they're finicky focus groups.
Yeah, because they're scared. There's too much money at stake. So they got to make sure, okay, we're not going to offend this group or that group. Because if we offend this group, then they're not going to come see the movie.
They're scared.
Blah, 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 blah.
Are you kidding me?
My dog is resting comfortably on my $2,000. What? Steve in Tampa. Steve.
Hey, Owen A.
What's up?
Hey,
buddy.
Yeah, right now my Labrador is resting comfortably on my $2,000 leather couch and very happy about it, I must say.
That's wonderful. Isn't that great?
Do you mind?
So this little dog ass right there on your couch.
Some people don't mind, though. Do you mind, Steve?
Just leaving puckered little dog ass prints on your couch.
Let's go to Jesse in Nebraska. Jesse.
Morning, boys.
Hey.
How you doing?
I'm good, Jesse.
Hey, I was wondering, will the fans throw puppies at Michael Vick whenever he throws an interception?
Oh,
I would imagine this is going to be a lot of stuffed animals being thrown onto the field.
No, I'm thinking
real puppies. Oh. People bring puppies and just hurl them out of the stands onto the field. Holy shit.
I love how Jesse had to clear it up. No, I mean real puppies.
I mean real puppies, just throwing puppies.
Well, we are talking about Philly.
Yeah,
that is true.
It's Philly's going to come alive with this. I'm telling you, they're going to be out of their minds today. I got a bunch of text messages actually last night. They could give a crap what he used to do.
Yeah,
in his spare time, they can't wait to see him in an Eagles uniform. All right, Jesse, thank you.
By the way, I was on Hannity last night.
Yeah,
why is this guy saying? Yeah, I mean, we don't have to get in depth with it, but hey, Rich.
Yeah, what happened last night? That liberal was walking all over you.
Are you out of your fucking mind?
What happened?
I destroyed that guy at every turn. Every fucking turn. Every all night, all I was getting was Twitters and reading how I fucking nailed that guy and I destroyed him. And you're the first person that has said I let him walk all over me. Example.
He was walking every time you had a point to make. He was interrupting you, and he was talking over you.
No. How about the fucking, the whole thing came up with Obama, and who the fuck came up with the idea
That's what happened last night. The liberal was good.
No, he wasn't. Of government-run healthcare. Who the fuck cut him off right there? Me.
Well, you did. But you know what he was doing? He's pulling that Sharpton move on you where he's like, no, you're wrong. That's not true.
Anybody that watched that saw it differently. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Who was it, Ann? I didn't see it.
Some liberal guy.
You don't know his name?
Why would I know his name?
Well, we're cutting up the appearance, so we'll find out for ourselves, Rich.
But I did meet Huckabee.
Oh, Mike Huckabee?
Yes, Mike Huckabee. Seems like a nice gentleman.
You're on with him?
Well, he was on earlier. He had like a one-on-one interview.
So you're on with some liberal guy and who else?
And some broad.
Oh, cool. You never know their names. I never know.
Why do I know their names? No, he's like, you know, liberal guy. You know, just I call him liberal guy.
Well, we'll get the audio very
soon.
It's
the sacrificial lamb, actually.
Yeah.
That they put on there.
Well, yeah.
He's in the Kobayashi Maru. Is what it is.
That's why I don't feel like going on that show.
Hannity doesn't stop with you, man.
I don't feel like going on that show and being way. I'll be completely honest. I'll be in way over my head. I don't give a shit about politics that much. And of course, he would go with that da-da-da-da-da right at me.
Sean wants you on so bad.
And I would rather talk about some other shit.
He wants you on so bad.
To do what? Beat me up?
I don't know. He just
keeps
saying.
To try to convince me that I need to be a right-wing Republican? I'm fine right where I'm at.
I told him, you know, because he said, he goes, you're not really a... I said I'm not really far right, conservative, Christian right.
Mm-hmm.
I go, I have ideas that lean, and I go, I'm not quite left. I go, I'm more center.
Right.
You know, so
I'm center.
Yeah.
I'm a moderate.
He wants you on that show.
I know it's not happening.
Oh boy, does he want you on?
Are you doing any reconnaissance on why certain people keep getting bumped?
No, they actually not why
they don't
people
really
get
want
bumped.
You.
But
they
no, they were
you.
Saying they said to say hello. Really they love you. Having you on the show.
Yeah, well, we'll see.
And I love the tell them we said hello.
That's the worst.
That's not going to make Jimmy feel
but
better.
But they did. We were talking about
what
Jimmy
did Sean say about me
and how great he is.
When the cameras were off, what did he say about me?
He said, "Get Opie on the goddamn show." That's what he said.
All right, what are we going to talk about?
I don't think he'd beat you up because he likes you.
I'll talk golf with him.
Yeah, he golfs.
I'll talk music.
Yeah.
I'll talk videos. I ain't going to talk that political
shit.
So,
dude, make fun of the whole process. Like, if you don't want to talk about the politics, just goof on the whole thing. Like, just make it like, you can certainly play it that way.
You could actually sit there and go, oh, here's where Sean goes at the liberal guy. All right, go ahead, Sean. Do your thing. And, like, totally throw a monkey wrench into the works.
Boy, it's like you know me or something.
That would be hysterical. Opie just throws a monkey wrench into the whole works.
Or completely misrepresent everything he says.
Yeah.
If Hannity goes off on something, go, you're right, Sean, and I know the typically you're for gay marriage, so let's talk. Completely misrepresent him.
But my proudest moment on Hannity was when he was doing it with Combs. And
see,
I am a seer. I mean, you guys just got to start realizing that. So Ann and I are on Hannity and Combs. And Hannity completely controlling the TV show, you know, back when he was doing it with Combs.
Yeah.
And Hannity, da-da-da-da-da-da, and we're talking and, you know, having a nice conversation with Hannity. And all of a sudden, Combs pipes up, and I turn around. I don't even listen to what he said. I go, what did I say exactly?
You said, Sean lets you talk?
Or something. I don't remember my line now. Oh, it talks, or you talk, something. Ah, fuck.
It was very nasty.
It was nasty, yeah. And he gave me a look like, fuck you. Where do you want to go with this? Ant looked like Sidney Friedman from Mass.
Sidney Friedman. People don't like my David Niven mustache.
Oh, your mustache on TV is fucking... You look like every fucking creepy poster by a school.
You know what?
Do not get into a van driven by this fucking Errol Flynn creep.
Errol Flynn!
You know what? I'm kind of with Jimmy. Like, in person... It looks fine, but something with the TV, I don't get it.
Yes, I know. I don't know what to do. I'll cut it off.
No, but right here it looks fine, but on TV, I don't know what the... I don't know
because his hair... We're used to Ant's hat.
Yeah,
when his hair is slicked back, I tweeted a picture of Ant on Hannity the first time he was on, and he looks like a guy defending marriage between adult males and small boys. He looks like a creepola.
Well, I didn't have it slicked back last night. It was a little poofy last night. It's growing a little more, so it was a little poofy. So I was able to ace the hat and take that off. And then, but my little, I shaved the mustache down so it wasn't so big. But I don't know. Yeah, there's something about just TV that just
go.
I'm a creep.
Come back with the goatee.
I don't know what to do. No,
do a little old school.
I got too much gray now.
Get the
it's
medicine.
Fucking,
diet.
Not
get
the
a medicine.
Medicine.
Margaret.
No.
Robert Kelly did the medicine for
no.
a while.
No. Then yeah. You're caught up. God, the worst thing was seeing Lemmy from Motorhead, and he uses the medicine, but he let it grow out.
Yeah.
So you see, like, the whole tips of the hairs are black, but then the roots of the beard hair is gray.
Yeah.
And that was happening. That happened to Dice too one day when he was in here. His big pork chop sideburns, just the tips were black and the roots were all gray. It's like, no, just shave it.
But the problem is, he came in, it was completely black. By the end of his appearance, the gray was already appearing.
Yeah, it's already coming back.
What's up with facial hair?
Weird.
I just shaved and I got like, look.
Big pain in the ass.
Unbelievable.
I wanted to get that picture of Aunt on Hannity.
I know. Well,
Danny, I tweeted one a while ago. Is there any way we can go back and grab it off the computer?
There was one from last night.
Oh, you got someone tweeted? Okay.
Or somebody tweeted one from last night, but yeah, I
Sean Hannity called me a pussy and a bedwetter. Oh yeah.
A bedwetting liberal is what it's called.
Did he call
it's
me
like
that
a
again?
A tree hugger or a bedwetting liberal.
He didn't call me that on the show, did he? Just behind the scenes?
Oh no, no, on the show, at the beginning of the show. He said, where is Opie, that bedwetting liberal?
Last night?
Yes.
I know exactly where he lives.
Oh, hell. Now you sound like one of our listeners to me.
I'm coming with my crew.
I'm a ghoul.
Let me see.
The hair looks better, but it's like, you just look weird.
Well, I'm making a fake. I took this picture.
I'm not used to seeing you without your hat, Ann.
I know.
That's not that bad.
No, he looks fine. It's
the hair is a bit poofy.
Errol Flynn.
You got some poofy hair.
Errol Flynn.
You know, Anthony? Anthony's a swarthy character.
No, I want TV. I just don't want political TV. I can't be bothered.
That's all the rage now.
You should just make fun of it. Make fun of the whole process.
Maybe.
I don't mind talking politics, but sometimes it gets a little too...
Yeah, you guys are way more in than me.
Sometimes it gets too much for me, and just make fun of the whole thing. Like, goof on it or just completely misrepresent what the person's saying.
Oh, I guess you enjoy paying taxes.
I do.
Yeah, I do, Sean. That's why I lean more Democrat. Yeah, you're right.
So, your guy, Obama, OP. Your boy, Obama. What do you think about the... healthcare and these town hall meetings where people are outraged at this. What do you think?
You're right, Shut Sean. You're right. Our president's retarded. I'm sorry for thinking differently. Ugh. God bless the people that could get into those political debates and fight.
It's just fun.
Yeah,
it's exhausting. It's fun to like.
It's exhausting because I hate being in any type of argument where you can't turn the other person.
No, why? There's no turning the other person.
Like when you have a disagreement with someone, and you could maybe find some like common ground or something, not in politics. When the other person talks, all you hear is like white noise.
During the commercial break, the guy actually...
I like that. Is that the black guy you were on with? I like him.
No, that was last time.
Okay.
Yeah, that was last time.
I've done it with him. He's a nice dude.
Yeah, you've done it with him? Big cock?
Mine was actually bigger. People were more ready for his to be bigger, and they were surprised.
That's the slick back hair.
Oh, they're fucking... Oh, holy shit.
That's the slicked back hair, Anthony.
Holy shit.
That was the last
File?
Time.
Mr. File?
That was the last time you were on. Wow.
Fucking Anthony.
Wow. Anthony. Your hair is way better now.
Yeah, it's grown
way
in.
Way better.
It was just starting to really grow in there, but I couldn't poof it. Or curl it. It wasn't growing in curly yet, is what the problem was.
That looks like a fucking. It looks like an in-between shoot interview with John Holmes, in like 1975.
That's the look I was going for. Thank you.
That is a John Holmes interview.
That really is hysterical. Pedophile.
Well, I can't wait to get the audio from your appearance. We're gonna have it in a few minutes. We got to move on because
it's terrible.
What a creep you look like.
Do I just look creepy?
We got to move on because we got way too much shit.
Oh, I love it.
But we're going to go back to the Hannity thing when we get the audio. Absolutely.
All right.
We did the Vic thing. Pretty much a 2-year deal. 1 year with an option. They're very excited in Philly, and there's a lot of outrage and blah, blah, blah. And we'll see how this plays out, okay? The other
Good
big,
luck to you.
Do you want to do this or the video?
I like that guy.
But. Really? Okay. Well, we got the helicopter video.
I haven't seen that.
You'll see it. It's pretty much on every TV station.
It's being played
today.
Everywhere.
Wow.
Yeah. That broke yesterday afternoon.
But you knew there was going to be one. That's amazing in today's day. And, nothing really happens.
Yeah, I don't think anything happens without it being on someone's fucking video, the phone or camera something.
They missed the Sully landing.
They did have video of it actually touching down the water.
There is video.
I guess what I should have said, they should have had much better video than what we ended up seeing.
Dude, the first plane hitting the towers, they got two shots of. Like, it's amazing to me that there is...
Well, the helicopter thing, I'm so pissed off by... I'm assuming it's a woman, and maybe that's bad for me to say.
Yeah.
But If you've seen the footage of the helicopter and the plane, she's got it. I'm going to say she. She's got it. You see the helicopter go crashing into the plane, pretty much chopping it in half. Next thing you know, she goes something like, oh, that's terrible. And now she's filming the bottom of the boat.
People
that
don't
she's on.
Think, like, they want to watch it, but don't think, maybe they ought to record this. Yeah,
because she's
like, it hits it. It's obviously now going to fall into the Hudson River. And the next shot, she puts the camera down, and now you're seeing the floor of the boat she's on.
Thanks for nothing.
You do nothing you do goes on. It's like, you can't even be a fucking kid toucher talking about pirates without somebody capturing it. Well, look at that picture.
Hey, wait a minute. But that was my last appearance.
But you really can't do anything without it being caught by somebody. But you want what did you do after?
But fine, she caught the impact, but then she completely blew it. You'll see. So many people will be frustrated when they see this footage. Like, oh my God, what was wrong with you? Why couldn't you continue with your videotaping?
I got scared.
Because obviously you knew that the end result was it was all going to end up in the river.
Yeah.
So why wouldn't you show that?
What the fuck?
Guy's on the news now, the Harlem business owner.
Yeah, we're gonna say that.
Tough cookie.
But the video thing, Jimmy, you made a good point with the Kennedy assassination.
The most frustrating case of should have gotten it was while JFK was being assassinated, there was a woman shooting the motorcade as it came. She was in the book depository. Hmm. And then she was
Book depository, Bill.
Yeah, knock it off. And then she started filming in the direction that Kennedy was traveling as he was shot. She was under the floor where Oswald was, or two floors lower. She didn't know how to operate a video camera, so when the shots rang out, this fucking dumb bitch is looking out the window and filming the treetops. She missed the whole assassination.
Can you see her videotape?
Oh, yeah, you could go YouTube.
Her video, whatever?
You absolutely can. I forget what it's called.
Did her videotape pick up the shots from Oswald?
I don't remember what audio she had, if any. Because, again, that was 62. I guess
could have just been one of those 64? Little 8-millimeter cameras with no sound.
Yeah.
Dude, you show people waving a lot.
She would have gotten it. There's a few films of it. I think there's actually three films of the assassination, but she would have had one from the angle Oswald was at.
And the footage starts off good where she's got Kennedy.
I think so. She's got him, the motorcade coming towards her.
Yep.
And then
before it made the left turn.
It was a corner building, so you just go the other way and boom, it starts going down. And she just
blew it.
Oh, dude, it's the fucking worst. Maybe one of the listeners knows what hers is called.
Right. Here. This is
the plane, and then the collision.
Oh my God!
You can hear the sheer horror of those who witnessed this fatal crash. The person who shot this footage is on the Circle Line.
How frustrating is that?
They're on the Circle Line.
But how frustrating is that?
She gets the impact and then puts it on her friend's shoulder. It's then on a woman's back.
Because she had to go, she had to put her hands to her face.
Oh, my God.
And that meant that the camera was going to now
kind
of fall down to the right, and now she's filming whoever was in front of her.
Suck it up.
Hey,
back.
I will say this. At least she got the impact. I mean, look, as much as she should be kicked into the water, but let me see it again.
But look, you see a plane, and then the collision.
Oh my God!
You can hear the sheer horror of those who...
And she shakes as it hits, so you kind of... Yeah. She really
the
does
person
stink.
Who shot this footage is on the Circle Line ferry. He focuses on the helicopter.
Hey, oh boy.
It's
sorry.
A guy.
Sorry to every woman listening to our show. I apologize.
Oh,
sorry.
God, what a shaky Sam. What?
Yeah. He's a loose he, if you know what I mean.
God damn this thought of him.
Investigators with the necessary clues as to what went so wrong that day.
How do you not continue filming?
But then it's perfectly steady until a quarter second before it hits.
Yeah, before impact.
And then it starts shaking.
Then he hands it to Katharine Hepburn.
Mr. Fox took this video.
All right, why don't we get into the story of the day? This fucking store owner.
If you can find that, just look for Kennedy assassination from, I don't know what it's called.
Yeah, I want to see that too.
You're going to want to dig this woman up and just kick her in the shins.
You know what? We haven't read a whole story in a long time, but who wants to do some reading today?
Reading's for queers.
I'm a great reader, though. I was voted boy most likely to read publicly.
Dude, you got...
You want to be voted.
Oh, yes, I did. Oh, I competed for years for
that. You did?
I certainly did.
Well.
You got a store owner in Harlem. Blast four robbers, killing two. The other two are in pretty bad shape. Old white guy. owns a restaurant supply company.
Yeah.
And, man, this guy wasn't going to take any guff.
No, he wasn't. He went old school.
By the way, Ant, because I'm not sure if you know this. I love stories like this.
Isn't
for
great?
Real. I'm not a big gun guy like yourself. But when I see, like, a store owner guy fighting back and blasting everyone in sight, I'm a big fan of the store owner.
Yeah, one for the good guys.
I'm a major fan of the store owner.
It's good, because that could have just been a story that was on page fucking, 12. That just said, store owner killed.
Right.
Employees killed in robbery of blah, blah, blah. And you'd be like, oh, okay. This one is, oh, wait, what happened? Well, I just like to think what the mindset is of the robbers when that happens. The second it starts turning bad, like the thought of like, holy shit, wait a minute, this wasn't supposed to go like this.
Right.
I'm supposed to go in, get some money, fucking leave. We're supposed to laugh.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's supposed to be good.
Well,
But now I'm bleeding profusely, and my friend is dead, and...
All four of them he got.
Yeah, what a
guy. We don't have to read the whole thing, but pump action ending. Two robbed suspects dead and two shot by storekeep with a shotgun. A shotgun-wielding owner of a Harlem restaurant supply company blasted two robbers to death and wounded two others yesterday when he caught them pistol-whipping his employee, police said. Turning the tables on the bandit, 72-year-old Charles Augusto opened fire with a 12-gauge shotgun he kept handy for such occasions.
Just such an emergency.
The cops and witnesses knew that. He was robbed before, so people aren't totally amazed that he took this type of action. They ran into some tough stuff today, witness Vernon McKenzie, 48, said of the stick-up men, including one whose bloody corpse was splayed. I've never seen that word before, splayed.
Splayed, just kind of thrown with arms and legs akimbo.
Sure. Splayed on the sidewalk in front of Augusta's store on West 125th Street near Amsterdam. The robber stormed into the business, Kaplan Brothers, Blue Flame, just after 3 p.m., demanding cash. He did a large cash business, a police source said. They were probably watching
the
place.
Force?
Police source?
Horses can't talk,
that's
Obie.
Crazy.
They just go, brr, and they eat oats.
Police
and
horse.
They have giant penises.
There's a lot of words. I'm trying to read real fast. He did a large cash business, a police source said. They were probably watching the place and made a move after a sell. Neighbor said Augusta, who was not charged last night, had sold a stove earlier in the day. He sold a stove.
I like using the oven.
A stove. My favorite bird is the bird of peace, the dove.
Holy shit.
That's great.
And, when I started reading this, I'm like, wow, I'm reading pretty good today.
Stuff is fine.
Stuff, holy shit. Sold the stove earlier in the day. The stick-up crew, three 21-year-olds and a 29-year-old. Do we know the race of the victims? Not that they should be called victims.
Yes.
No, the perps.
The perps, yes.
I don't know yet.
Well, they're not mentioning what they were.
I'm going to guess black or Hispanic just because of where it was. It
was location.
125th in Amsterdam and Harlem.
Yeah.
You could have white criminals there. It's just less
likely.
You'd
have to be crazy to be a white criminal up there, I think.
Yeah, sure. Three white guys running with guns.
Yeah.
You got four. They came prepared with a pistol and plastic handcuffs. They tried to tie up two of Augusta's employees. The male employee started to struggle, and then as he did that, the perp with the gun struck him once in the head. Now, this is where the story gets great.
Yeah.
That's when the owner opened fire with the shotgun. Cocaine!
That is extreme.
As the bandits bolted from the store, Augusto squeezed off three blasts from the pistol grip shotgun. Is that a nice gun, Ant?
Well, it's probably an old one with the butt sawed off. I just picture this guy with an old one with the butt sawed off and the pistol grip handle.
Yeah.
How far away are they accurate to? He got all four guys.
A shotgun?
Yeah, you
get a little more leeway with a shotgun.
Yeah, that's like spraying some shit.
Yeah.
But isn't it hard to get off four quick shots? Like,
you have
to pump each one, right?
This guy's probably pretty good. Yeah, he got four shots off before they could run out the door.
Well,
that ain't bad.
He squeezed off three blasts from the pistol grip shotgun from 20 to 30 feet away from the pistol-whipped employee. Here we go. He was deadly accurate. The four bandits, who were all from Manhattan, were hit. Two of the robbers were struck in the back. One dropped dead inside the store among the sparkling gas stoves, a pistol near his body. How great is that? The other, a nephew of a cop in the NYPD.
Oops.
Made it across the street before collapsing on the sidewalk. Police and witnesses said he was later pronounced dead at St. Luke's Hospital. The furious employee, this is where it's unbelievable, who had been pistol-whipped, ran out of the store and leaned over the mortally wounded bandit, cursing at him, witnesses said. The worker went back into the store and dragged the other dead thief onto the sidewalk. Okay, so this wasn't the shooter. I thought it was the shooter. This was one of the employees that were being pistol-whipped.
Yeah, that was being pistol-whipped.
Okay, it wasn't the shooter.
I think the shooter also did it.
Okay. The worker went back into the store and dragged the other dead thief onto the sidewalk, yelling at him and kicking him. He stood over the body, cursing him and shaking him. The guy's dead and bleeding, just bleeding. And he's shaking the guy, and he goes, wait. Okay. He stood over the body, cursing him and shaking him, even though he was dead. He was screaming at him and stomping him. He said, "You were going to kill me? Well, now you're dead."
Nice.
Jesus. And then ran over to Gus and said, "You saved my life," blah, blah. It goes on and on. Basically, Augusta bought the shotgun after a robbery nearly 30 years ago.
Nearly 30 years ago?
So 30 years ago, he was robbed. He said, "Fuck that. That's never happening again."
Oh, if that's a 30-year-old shotgun, yeah, I'm sure it was nice sawed off.
Yeah.
Probably kept it all nice right there for just such an occasion.
Now, they're not sure if he has a license for the weapon. Let me see.
Yeah, New York City, you need a license to even have a shotgun or a rifle.
He's not been arrested or charged. A police source said that if Augusto is hit with a charge, it will be a minor one. It doesn't look too bad for him, the source said.
Yeah, handguns are one thing. Shotgun, I think I'm not sure if you need a license for it, but I think it has to be registered. I think you have to have it registered.
A handgun's a bigger charge, though?
A handgun, a handgun is, if you're not licensed to own a handgun in New York City, it's mandatory 2-year sentence. And shotgun's another thing. It might be grandfathered in, though. If he's had it for 30 years, I'm not sure what the laws were 30 years ago in New York City, but you could be allowed to have it.
And a guy protecting his store is probably a little different.
Yeah,
you're a store owner protecting your store.
Well, look at crazy Bernie Getz. You know, he didn't get in trouble for shooting,
and he shouldn't have
anybody. He got in trouble for on a weapons charge.
Concealed weapon, right?
Yeah, and again, they found that those guys were gonna do violence towards him. So it really doesn't matter. You're going to fucking prison if you have a handgun in the city and don't
well,
have
you're
a
an
license.
You're an expert on this stuff, Ant. Jared has kind of a thought. Jared in Boston.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Just to preface this guy fucking rules, but Anthony, back me up on this one. Maybe if the cops don't get him on anything, I see one potential problem. I heard that you said two of the guys were shot in the back.
Yep.
I see some sort of a civil lawsuit, wrongful death.
Definitely.
They were fleeing the scene. This guy's a fucking hero, and some fucking scumbag family member, one of these douchebags, is going to bring something against him.
You're absolutely right. I do believe this guy is going to be in civil court, if not criminal court. But shooting the guys in the back, excessive force, they were fleeing, you're supposed to leave them alone. If they're leaving,
it was absolutely warranted. One of the guys own employees was getting pistol whipped. I mean,
but you know what you know what the guy could say? Yeah, they were running out, but the one guy still had a gun, and I could have sworn he was turning or he stopped to turn, and I shot him. You know, there's plenty of things this guy could say, but
he'll never. Me and Anthony discussed this too. I saw the same thing in the back, but they're in his store. No one's going to convict him. He's going to be convicted of nothing because, again, what's to prevent those guys from running 5 more feet and then just both of them turning around and blasting at him again? It's like those guys were armed. They were in his store. He absolutely is 100% right to shoot them
dead. I don't think a grand jury will indict him, but
no way.
I think a civil suit is definitely in his future.
Maybe.
Would it be different if the guys made out of the store and were now running across the street?
Absolutely different.
Absolutely.
That would be a major difference,
big problem for him if he does that.
Yeah,
you can't do that.
Right on.
All right, boys.
Thank you.
You could just say things, Kenny.
Here comes
something
Kenny.
Called eminent domain.
Yes.
No.
Yeah. Why don't
oh,
we?
Oh, you wrote eminent.
Kenny's an expert.
Imminent.
Let's go.
Eminent front.
Kenny, what do you got?
Imminent danger.
It's called eminent danger.
Oh. What's it mean?
It means, like you said, at the time he might have been run away, but at any point, you know, he still could present a danger.
Now, yeah. Once he left the store, was crossing the street, then you just can't blast at him.
Yeah, if they're legitimately fleeing, and you know, there's no.
But he's in the threat. Right.
Now. You know, there's got to be. You know, the threat has to be present.
He won't get in any Dutch.
right.
I bet civil Dutch. I bet. He won't lose. I bet that family's gonna just. Oh, boy. Ooh, he was a good boy. He got in some trouble with drugs, but he was trying to get himself out of it. Mm-hmm. That's every excuse in First 48 is he was really good, and he was tied up in drugs, but he was trying real hard to get out of it for him and his baby. he's like fucking 16.
Dude, no jury, though. No Harlem jury, no jury. Is going to convict this guy, a store owner, defending his store from a fucking...
Yeah, this guy's defending his play. Well, if you can't do this in this society, just, you know, fucking cash it in. Yeah.
We'll be watching this one closely.
Yes, we'll keep you posted.
Are you Google mapping the storefront?
Yeah, it's weird. The address that they give in the story, it's just kind of like a scaffolding. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it might be a newer store from when these pictures were taken.
Maybe he moved because he's been in business a long time.
Look up Stub Salesman.
Charlie in Philly. Charlie,
what's up? Hey, what's Charlie. Up, boys?
What do you think of the Michael Vick thing?
I could care less. I hate the Eagles.
Are you a are you a football fan though?
Yes, I am.
What's your team?
Actually, I like the Buccaneers.
All right, hold on a minute, because let's get into this a little bit.
Yeah, me too.
My father-in-law is pretty much born and raised in Philly. Well, he was whatever. Spent most of his life in Philly, and he's a Dolphins fan. How does that work?
Mm. Probably many many years ago when they were so good and undefeated. Even though he's older, but back then he might have
jumped on the bandwagon.
Yeah,
and our old friend Joey Paisano couldn't be more. He is the typical New Yorker, and he's a huge Eagles fan. Even though he's hardcore Yankees, and he loves all the other New York sports teams, but he doesn't like the New York football teams. He's an Eagles fan.
Mm.
How does that happen? It's weird.
I don't know. That is weird.
Were you born in Philly, Charlie?
Oh, that's his project.
Yeah, on the outskirts. I live about an hour north.
So why did you decide you wanted to be a Tampa Bay Buccaneers fan?
Believe it or not, I was always a Raider fan growing up. And when the Bucs started, when they picked up Warren Sapp, John Lynch, Mike Allstott, I mean, I followed those guys in college. I'm like, this team's going to be good someday. Because I follow players more than teams. Like right now, the Bucs are probably going to suck for the next 10 years just because of everything they're going through now.
I couldn't possibly enjoy this phone call, Les.
I know.
And it's nothing against you, sir. I just don't care about the Buccaneers.
Buccaneers.
Yeah, there's such a who gives a shit team, Charlie.
I know.
Well, I know. Can I ask Anthony a question, though?
Charlie.
Yeah, Charlie. Sure.
Anthony, I don't know about New York, but in Pennsylvania here, when you buy a shotgun, it comes with a plug where you can only put 3 shells in it.
Oh, yeah.
Got all 4 rounds?
No, there's not a law against that in New York. I know you got those plugs where you can only put fucking 4 shells in or 3 shells in. That's ridiculous.
Talk
Come on.
That.
Load it up.
Exactly. All right, boys, have a good vacation. And she was a stewardess. Later.
We're big fans of the inside stuff on this show. There's a bunch of people out there going, what the fuck does that mean? Well, you should listen a little longer. What can I tell you?
The Google map of the location where that store is right across the street from the projects, by the way.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. It just looks like a nasty, nasty
place.
You
think that guy was scared?
Look.
You think that guy was scared to go to work every day?
Gus. No. Gus went to work every day just hoping. Look, it's right across the street. The projects.
Which one is that?
I don't know. The put in some famous... oldie time black guy name
Frederick
here.
Something's houses.
Frederick, something houses.
You got to see the Roberto Clemente.
The Roberto Clemente projects?
Holy shit.
That's the George Washington Carver peanut butter project.
That could be the scariest one in the city.
Cabrini Green's is a notoriously bad one if that still exists in Chicago.
Wow, Chicago. And the train runs right through the fucking projects. What a shithole. Oh, the L is right there.
But they got opportunities to get out and make something of themselves, right?
Well, they do. Everybody does.
It is a shitty situation.
Well,
are you the House liberal, Francis?
There's the Q&A.
Yes. House
liberal. Yeah, those people have it tough up there, sir. Are you the House liberal, Francis?
Listen to this guy. His father's friend. Well, Mike, why don't you tell the story? You're from PA, too?
Already.
Yes, sir.
Are you Eagles fan?
No, I'm in Western PA. I don't think I'm allowed to be.
All right, simmer down.
What, are you a Steelers fan?
Panicky, sir.
I guess so, if I have to be. I don't know. I had a buddy.
What's wrong with you guys, man? Football season. I'm getting the feeling that this is going to be a really good football season. Anyone else? You kind of feel it, right?
No.
A lot of strong teams out there. And it doesn't follow football.
No.
You could.
I don't either.
No. Drew Boogie in the corner getting ready to play for us in a minute or so. All right. Go ahead, Mikey.
I had a motorcycle shop here in Western Pennsylvania for a long time, and it was repeatedly robbed kind of out in the country there. And so he went and put a fence over the windows like you guys have up there. That's unusual in this area. And they pulled the fence off one night and went in and stole some new motorcycles, dirt bikes mostly. And then one night he had it all back together, new window, new fence, sleeping behind the counter. A couple guys come up, hooked onto the fence, pulled it off, smashed the window, came in. He shot one guy in the chest with a... I think it was a 410 or a 20 gauge, but the guy landed outside. There was no blood inside, so they sued him. He ended up losing the franchise and ultimately his livelihood.
I've heard those.
Schmuck with a job.
I've heard those stories.
Amazing.
I don't know.
That's fucking amazing.
That doesn't make any sense.
Hi, buddy.
All right. Thank you, Mike. Hey, Danny, could you, before we go to break, could you give old, what's his name again? Augusto? Give a little Augusto something.
Sure.
Cole fucking K.
Absolutely. Gus Augusto gets the first Cole fucking Kane today.
Cole fucking Kane. You know what? We never got the inspirational speech from Rocky.
We can do that.
Right? Daniel found it.
I want to see.
Well, we're all over the place. You
I know.
Do it before the break.
Yeah, because I want. All right. I just want to see Jimmy get all douche.
Dude, it's fucking right now. He's standing there. He has the of course he does. The American flag is draped around him. And you know when Sly wrote this and read it in the fucking in the read through, they all went, "Wow, it's very inspirational, Sylvester."
Yeah.
Nobody would say, "Hey, you fucking hairless blithering idiot. That stinks. It's trite, and you're a bore. Stop trying to be meaningful."
And now there's Russians behind him. And the translator, remember there's a translator there that has to translate everything Rocky's saying. And he's ready to give the inspirational speech. He turned the crowd around.
And great, he's talking to fucking Sid, the sports guy. Who the fuck that?
He does look like Sid.
Creepy guy with the microphone.
You know what we could do is... We change.
Shut up.
Rocky. Rocky.
Let's listen to this dude.
That's a garbage.
Thank you. Thank you.
I came here tonight. I don't know what to expect.
Can you pause that?
Yeah.
I knew what to expect. A douche chill moment. And boy, did you deliver.
As he's talking, they're panning the crowd. And you see military guys, you know, Russian army guys are standing there listening intently to the words of Rocky, Rocky.
It's like, we get it. They're Russian. They're trying to stress. They have, like, Russian lady hats on and shitty coats.
Yeah, babushkas.
Why don't you just all wear signs with a big R on them? We get it. We know where you are.
All right. Okay.
See, a lot of people hating me, and I didn't know what to feel about that, so I guess I didn't like you much, none either.
Я думаю, что я не любил их тоже.
That's it?
That's it?
Come on.
During this fight, I've seen a lot of changing.
В течение всего этого боя я понял, что многое изменилось.
The way
here it comes.
You felt about me and the way I felt about you.
И я почувствовал, что вы тоже изменились.
In here. There were two guys showing each other.
Drago.
But I guess that's better and 20 million.
Pause that, please.
Jimmy's head is in his hand. Jimmy. He is disgusted.
Jimmy!
Look at the Politburo is up there watching, and now they're being inspired. The entire Politburo.
Yes. And I think that that woman over there, Drago's wife, I'm going to marry her. Isn't that Brigitte Nielsen?
Yeah.
Did he marry her?
I think he did.
The funniest
thing. He at least fucked the shit out of her.
Oh, this is fucking horrendous.
And fake Gorby. The guy that played Gorbachev in every fucking Russian, they needed a Russian leader in the 80s movie. Guy.
You know, he's just right now going through scripts. He probably downloads all scripts and he puts the word Gorbachev search, and if it's not in the script,
yeah,
throws it out.
Just move on.
Yeah.
Spill some grape juice on his head and then just. He's ready to roll.
Trying to say is, if I can change.
Я думаю, что каждый тоже изменился.
You can change.
Вы можете измениться.
Pause that again.
They're all. They're
if I can change, you can change. Everybody can change.
Yeah.
Very inspirational, dumbbell.
Well, they're all clapping now. The whole crowd is behind Rocky.
Over a fight?
Well, it's more than just a fight.
We barely changed after 9/11.
Yeah, who gives a shit?
We barely changed after 9/11. Oh. We're supposed to change after a fight?
Ugh.
Ugh.
Look, look. Gorby stands up.
No.
Yeah. Gorby stood up and did the slow clap.
The golf clap, but now he's really clapping.
And now, like, the head of the KGB stood up.
One thing to my kid who should be home sleeping. Merry Christmas, kid!
You see what you got to do? Fuck! Fight it!
And now a great song by Sly's brother, Douchebag Stallone.
Yep. All right.
I cannot.
Are you embarrassed?
I am so fucking chilled, dude.
I got
look,
the chills of the douche variety.
Yeah, I got goosebumps, and they're not from something good.
Abu.
Abu.
The guy who looks like Gorbachev stood up and does like the slow.
He did the slow collab, like they were all waiting. It was like, does Mikey like it? Kind of a moment. He stood up and it was a little bit of tension. With the Russians, like, uh-oh, am I in trouble for clapping at Rocky? And then he's like, and they're all like, okay, it's okay to clap.
All right, our first break.
Rocky, the Russian Rocky.
Yuck. Drew, where are you?
Go through
on this
a 20-minute fucking speech, and the Russian guy goes, a clap at the
door. I have no idea.
The fuck is that?
Yeah, a goulash.
Those Russians don't fucking talk long, do they?
No, they're very to the point, Latin people. The mafia. Kill you. They don't play games, the Russians.
No.
Where? Mars, what are you doing?
All right.
What are you pointing at?
We got Drew Boogie in the studio. Hold on a second there.
Oh.
When we get back, we got some audio of Ant on Hannity. And I see there's a couple fucking Opie mentions. I'm going to get into this a little bit.
Well, yeah, there were a couple of mentions. You know, Hannity wants you on the show.
I'm going to fuck him up.
No qualms about that.
I'm going to bring Kenny with me, and I'm going to have him fucked up.
Aw, hell.
Also, other things.
Inspirational speeches.
We haven't fucked with Regis in a while. He sounded like a complete dummy. He had Kate from John and Kate Plus 8 on.
Yeah.
And he did some just dumb stuff with her.
Uninformed
stuff. You would think if you're going to have, like, Kate on, maybe you should know the show a little bit.
Do a little research.
We'll explain. And I know a lot of people are sick of this, but Bobo's new bit on the way.
Bobo's new bit.
And
you got to give it to Bobo. It's always something new.
Well, no, it has nothing
no, it
to do
isn't.
With Bobo.
Of course not.
See, what you and I forget, and the listeners, we forget about Bobo.
Yeah.
After he's in this studio, we forget about him.
I don't even think
not
about
Sam,
him.
Not Danny, not Travis.
They're obsessed with him.
And they spend the whole week fucking with Bobo.
If I could change and you could change, maybe we could all change and not make fun of me as much.
So,
by the way, was it last week?
Yeah.
Bobo was here on Friday, but we were very busy.
Yeah.
And he didn't come in. They made him sit in a box.
Yeah.
The entire time he was here.
Well, that was after he actually got here. We had called Bobo last Friday, probably about 5:15, to make sure he was coming.
Yes.
And we told him to hurry up because we wanted to use him for a bit ASAP, probably start of the show. So he goes, "Oh, okay, I'll run there. I'll get off the train and just run." And then we never even had him on the show at all.
And not even didn't have him on the show. He kept him in a box, a giant box. The entire time.
I made a I made a 4-minute video of that.
Did you?
It's on my YouTube channel, OP Radio. I'm glad you mentioned it. Bobo has become like the undercard for the OP and Anthony show.
Yeah, yeah.
He's not part of the broadcast anymore. No. He's kind of like I don't know. They just fuck with him when we're.
It's a dark match. They call those.
What is it?
It's a dark.
Oh
match.
Yeah, dark match. Thank you.
They don't make the television.
Yeah, no, not at all. But with that said, these guys have been working with Bobo for the last week, even though you and I and the rest of the audience forgot about Bobo.
Yeah.
And Bobo's new bit is on the way. It is very funny. These guys are ruthless with this Bobo.
Terrible, terrible people.
All right, day before vacation. That means Drew Boogie's in the house. Drew, you plugging anything?
CD. MySpace.com/TheGreatDrewBoogie. CD's still up there.
Nice, good. I liked it.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
I downloaded it from iTunes.
I've run through it a few times. Very, very good stuff on there.
Ah, thank you.
So Drew Boogie's going to play us in and out of break today, the day before vacation. So take it, Drew.
Holy shit, I want to break stuff.
Drew Boogie doing that live in studio today. How cool is that?
That is extreme.
That fucking is extreme. The Opie and Anthony show day before vacation.
They're like yelling cocaine in there. That's crazy.
We got Jay Oakerson stopping by. We got Patrice O'Neill stopping by, I think within 10, 15 minutes.
Nice.
We got Jeremy Piven calling about his new movie, The Goods. I think that opens today, right?
The Goods. Yep.
And that's not all. On our phones right now is Mr. Bill Burr. Bill!
Hey, what's up, guys?
Whoa, Bill!
Hi, Bill.
How are you?
What's up, Mr. Burr?
We fucking missed you.
Hello,
Bill Burr.
Anthony. How are you, sweetheart?
Very good, love. How you been? Miss you.
Hey, Bill, are you doing a movie or something?
Yeah, I did that back in June. I had 1.5 lines.
Oh,
in
really?
A major motion picture.
That's good.
Major? Which one?
Paging Mr. Herman.
Paging Mr. Herman. You have a telephone call at the front desk.
I was in a movie called Date Night starring Tina Fey and Steve Carell.
Jesus.
I guess it comes out sometime in 2010.
Did you have was your scene with either one of them?
No.
Jesus. Every question you ask, Jimmy,
is a bad answer.
It's a dig at Bill and his
but
career.
But I wasn't actually.
Actually,
I'm
wait
teasing.
A minute. You know what it is? I'm sort of like in the scene, but I never talk to either one of them. I just sort of poke my head in and go, "Hey, so-and-so, you got a phone call. I swear to God." And then I'm out.
Well, I mean, this is
You guys are starting to get in a lot of movies, a bunch of you guys, but it's like a little scene here, a little scene there. When are you going to get the big hit? When is Bill Burr going to get the big hit? When is Jim Norton going to get the big hit? When is Patrice O'Neill going to get the big hit? How does that work?
I think, you know what? I think I have to take an improv class.
Oh,
Bill.
Oh, no.
Bill, come on.
It seems like those are the guys. They're like, I don't know. That's like, you really need that skill. I had a big audition the other day, and I think I blew it because just being a comedian.
Oh, you got to come out of, like, the Groundlings or something?
I got to admit, yeah, those are the guys who booked that stuff. But, but I don't know. Zach Galifianakis has been doing good, so I don't know.
But they're starting to pay attention to all you guys, so I just, it's probably just a matter of time before you get a major role in one of these things.
Hey, yeah, Bill. I'm hoping to get... I don't know, just one of those one or two scene things, and I don't know, I'm going to always do stand-up, so I just want to get in one of these, so I have to do, less radio when I'm on the road.
Yeah, you don't like doing that radio, huh?
I mean, I'm not talking about your show, I'm talking about the other one.
I know, everyone says the same thing, which we appreciate.
I want a blockbuster hit that I'm the star of and responsible for.
It's
going to happen eventually.
No, it won't.
Hey, Bill, what about Michael Vick? You're a big sports fan.
Oh, my God. I'm psyched he's coming back. And I think people who are sitting there going, like, he doesn't seem like he's remorseful. He doesn't have to be. He did his time. He got 2 years. Yep. He did it, you know, like a man. Like, if you rob a bank and they give you 8 years and you get out, there's nobody sitting there going, oh, he doesn't seem like he's remorseful that he robbed the bank.
I agree.
So I think he ought to be able to drop kick a beagle on the 50-yard line at this point. The guy lost $100 million. He went to Leavenworth, dude. John Gotti went to Leavenworth. He did this for dogs. Somebody else killed somebody drinking and driving. They got 30 days in jail. He doesn't owe anything to anybody. I don't think he should have gone to Philly, though.
Why?
I don't know. It's just going to cause a quarterback controversy. And
Oh, well, that's true.
I don't know. He should have gone to Detroit. That would have appeased the animal lovers because it would have been like an extension to his sentence. And then he also could have been like the hero, like try to, you know, turn that awful franchise around, you know?
Yeah, Bill.
I just don't see, like, Philly. They already have Donovan McNabb. I don't know.
Well, we mentioned when this was all starting to go down, we're like, it's obvious that Michael Vick will end up with an ugly, dirty type team.
Dirty team like this.
Like, he's not going to go to the Colts or some of those nice white bread type teams. You know what I mean? We figured it.
I thought it was going to be the Raiders.
We said Raiders. We said Detroit. We said the Eagles. There were a few others on the short list, and sure enough, the Eagles grabbed them.
Cowboys too. It's like
a
team of criminals.
Right.
Yeah, that's actually a good call. Maybe he should have played for the University of Miami.
Bill, how much money did he lose?
Like $100 million.
Holy shit!
Yeah, that's gotta hurt.
Oh,
that's gotta hurt when you really think about it.
An endorsement, of course. Like, I'm also, as always, repeating something I overheard in a bar, but I know it was tens of millions of dollars.
Wow.
The guy lost. He lost his houses. He's broke. He lost 2 years of his career, and he went to Leavenworth.
Wow.
What the fuck? What else does this guy have to fucking do? You know what it is? People are miserable with their own lives. If at this point, if you just, like, they just want to see him, they want to see a broken man.
Yeah, but
they want to see him on his knees and fucking have a heartfelt moment with a Cocker Spaniel. I mean, I don't know what the fuck they want from this guy. But, I mean, because I don't condone what the guy did. It was, like, bizarre. And, but, I mean, shit. He did all his time. He wasn't like Paris Hilton, who was there for a day and a half and fucking went home.
Started crying, and her mommy came and got her. Yeah.
Has anybody actually come out against it, though? Or is it just that people are expecting it?
PETA doesn't like him very much.
Yeah, PETA. Well, this just, out when Obama swatted a fly.
This just hit, so I'm sure we'll hear from PETA and everyone else as the day goes on. So,
They'll say, we're disappointed. We're going to protest. That's going to be... I want to see if the PETA people are going to have the balls to stand outside... they don't play at Veterans Stadium. Wherever the fuck the Eagles play now.
Yeah, the new place.
All those maniac Philly fans.
Yeah.
That might be worth it, just to watch a couple of them get pounded.
But because the guy went to jail,
I wonder if people are going to have a problem with it. It's really hard to argue with a guy who did time in prison and served a sentence. I mean, it's like you, the guy, that's what our whole country is. It's like once your time is served, you kind of get to start over.
Absolutely. There will definitely be protests, though. Just that's just how it is. So.
Yeah, no, I that's kind of what I'm basing this all. Like, I've been watching, you know, ESPN, and I've listened to a little bit of radio, and there's people still complaining, and their argument is he hasn't said anything. He doesn't sound remorseful. Dude, people fucking love dogs. They love them more than they love people.
That's what we say. Yeah, we were just saying that. It's like people just freak out when in a movie a dog gets hurt. People are like, oh, but it could be just a huge body count and no one gives a shit. Like, people love treating dogs like they're part of the family. We're a crazy nation.
Yeah, but he was a piece of shit with them. Even though I think he should be able to play. And he should be left alone. He was a complete piece of shit. It wasn't like he just hit a dog because he was being careless. He was a fucking absolutely. Complete vulture.
Absolutely. But there was a guy, one of those guys, a guy in the Browns, he was driving drunk and he killed somebody. The guy did 30 days.
Yeah.
He killed, you know, a bunch of dogs. And he did 2 years in Leavenworth and lost, you know, evidently $100 million, according to the cokehead, two bar stools down from me.
and now because of that, we're going to quote that all day long.
Yeah.
And we got our info from Bill, who got it from some cokehead at a bar.
At a bar.
So.
But there you go. Now it's
but that's how
true.
It works. That's how we all work. Who are you kidding? Hey, Bill, you're doing the New York Comedy Festival. That's huge.
Yeah, I'm calling up to whore myself out. I'm going to be performing at Town Hall on November 6th, and the tickets go on sale today. I'm kind of gearing up for another special, and that Town Hall date will probably be about 3 weeks away from me taping my special. So if you can't make it to my special, go to that show, because that'll essentially be the special.
Who are you working with, do you know?
I am working with young Joe DeRosa.
Oh!
Teen Idol. Of the Opie and Anthony show.
Teen Idol.
We love Joe. You got to move back to New York, Bill, because, you know, he's taking your spot.
Well, listen, dude, I got to tell you, if I can, like you were saying, when are you going to get that breakout role? If I can get some shit where I can actually, I wasn't getting any auditions for stuff like this in New York. Some guys do, but it wasn't happening for me.
Yeah.
So that's the reason why I went out there, you know.
Yeah, of
15
course.
Years into doing stand-up, and I go meet a casting director out there, and they'd just be like, so you do comedy. I gotta climb up this one now. So
hey Bill, I got your plug sheet in front of me. I don't want to confuse everyone, but what I got is that the tickets go on sale August 17th, which would be
that's what I was trying to say. I was just trying to make sure you guys were paying attention. I'm a little worse.
Well, I don't know. Are you right or are we right?
Oh, you're right. You're right.
Okay, because you know, people are going to start calling or what the fuck. They're going to get confused, and then they're going to give up. Tickets go on sale for Bill Burr's Town Hall date, Friday, November 6th here in New York City. Monday, Ticketmaster.com, NewYorkComedyFestival.com as well. These tickets will sell real fast. Hey, I was at the Helium Comedy Club in Philly over the weekend. And they got one of your T-shirts in the case there. I was laughing my ass off. Bill Burr has a T-shirt where, explain it, Bill. It's when you took on Philly, and I believe it's the Liberty Bell, and then it's a lot of the stuff that Bill said.
Wow, really?
On the back of the shirt. As
you're saying this, I'm hoping it's not Bill's shirt. I hope they stole it.
I only sold those in Philly. I did when I came back there. I had one of those. It was basically. I should get into the shit. I was kind of going back and forth with, I was just dealing with some bullshit with selling my CD, and I just didn't want to sell it anymore, and I just said to hell with it. So I just did like a one-off sort of T-shirt the last time I went through there.
Yeah.
And well, I don't have any left.
Who's giving you shit about your CD? Was it the people who made it?
Yeah, I kind of got into one of those behind the music contracts.
Oh, shit.
And then I realized that it wasn't great. So then I was like, I know what I'm going to do. I'm not going to sell my CD. I'm going to sell a T-shirt instead. So I went down there with all these T-shirts, and I sold like 8 of them, and I felt like a jackass. And, and then
sorry
I had
to
a DVD, so.
Well, the reason.
That was a low moment.
The reason I bring it up, the people I were with, they all want one. So I'm assuming that if you threw it up on your website, a bunch of people would get it, especially the people that saw you just rip apart the crowd in Philly a couple summers ago.
Well, you know, maybe I'll I've always had a problem selling something that wasn't that didn't have like material on it. You know, I might as well be selling like refrigerator magnets and shit like that. So I kind of just did it in a moment of being pissed about the CD thing. And then I was standing there selling CDs, and I felt like more of a whore than I usually do after a show when I peddle my wares, as they say.
Hawk your goods.
Do you realize that was 3 years ago, that Philly show?
No.
That was 2006.
Get the fuck out of here. Huh? Three summers ago already?
Yep. September.
Holy shit.
Wow, it's fucked up.
All right, Bill. November 6th, Town Hall as part of the New York Comedy Festival. Tickets go on sale Monday, Ticketmaster.com.
Okay, beautiful. Thank you for liking my gigs. Always nice to talk to you guys, and hopefully I will be back on the East Coast soon, and I will be in there running my mouth.
Yes.
See you soon, love.
Miss you, Bill.
I'll miss you guys.
Take it easy, man.
The awkward ending to the phone call. Now what?
And it's funny, because Bill made a good point about, like, tickets going on sale and stuff.
Oh, really?
Oh, no.
Oh, no, this is not about my tickets.
No?
Oh. No. Fuck that. I don't care. Whatever you're doing today, ignore noon. Who gives a shit? Long Island tickets for Jim Norton? not important.
About that.
Who cares?
It's not even about that.
Don't even waste your breath October 2nd in Bayshore today at noon.
Please. Why would you even care that they go on sale today at noon?
Dude, people are like, why don't they sell them earlier? And I'm like, why don't you call 866-811-3111 and yell?
No one's going to be there yet.
No, not now.
Start
noon.
Yelling at noon.
At noon, yeah. Yell. Buy tickets first, then yell.
Do it or don't do it.
It's up to you.
Yeah.
Patrice O'Neill in studio.
Patrice.
Good morning.
I have a feeling you might have something to say about the Michael Vick thing. Because I remember when this whole thing went down.
Can I?
you were like, you guys don't understand the culture of what goes on.
I love dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Love them more than people, as Bill was saying. I love dogs.
I knew you'd have something to say.
I couldn't stand what he did. People who are vicious to animals bug me, you know, especially if you're up at 4 o'clock in the morning watching I Love Lucy and Sarah McLachlan comes on.
I will remember. Oh,
and showing a picture of a kitten with conjunctivitis.
Yeah.
And a fucking puppy smoking a cigarette with a fucking headache bag on. If that motherfucker, if you don't feel bad for animals after you watch a fucking watery-eyed kitten.
Dude, that is the fucking worst commercial.
It's in between fucking Carol Burnett, fucking Guthrie Ranker selling Carol Burnett. And a Lucy
and it's so long, the commercial, too.
And a fucking...
It was on and on.
A pit bull puppy missing a paw, snorting cocaine, and he has no home. Now, if you don't fucking feel for an animal after you watch that, you're a fucking serial killer.
There's a one-eyed cat.
You're a hunk of shit. If a kitten with a fucking with pink eye doesn't fuck you up, you're a cocksucker. Look at it. Turn the shit off.
I don't want to see that shit.
I don't want to see that.
We're
man.
Watching the commercial.
Yeah, the dog with the paralyzed back legs.
Oh, fucking no.
Oh, look at that. What a bad boy he's been. Sam, you must have misbehaved.
Dude, I can't even look at that commercial. It ruins me.
I'm Sarah McLachlan.
Yes, this bitch.
I spread peanut butter on my pussy.
Yes. Let the dog lick it off.
All she sings is sad songs.
I know.
And it gets sadder and sadder, bitch. Kill yourself.
Throw a frisbee to that fucking thing.
These poor animals, man.
Well, that looks like a healthy dog.
Exactly. Well, the whole thing's about money.
Look at the poor. It ain't about
kitten.
Money. A kitten. Kittens with a headache is the worst thing ever.
A fucking headache bag.
I love that. Old school cartoon headache bag and a cigarette and fucking deep thoughts and shit. I don't need it.
God damn, Patrice.
I love animals.
A three-legged cat.
Jesus.
Three-legged cat.
What's wrong with that dog? That dog looked normal.
I don't know. Looking more. I don't.
What's wrong with these animals? They well, most of them look
how
okay.
How long is this fucking infomercial?
It's forever. This goddamn thing takes so long.
Yeah, but you don't know what these animals did to bother the owner. They don't share the whole picture.
I refuse to look at it any longer, man.
Guy's fucking scrubbing his pots and pans with a kitten's eye.
Yeah, exactly.
Who are these people who hate animals, man?
No,
I love animals, terrible. But I will punch a kitten square
belly in the middle of its face. If it mews while I'm watching TV, I will punch it squarely in its face.
If it mews.
Fucking assholes, man. So Danny brought that shit right up.
Of course he did.
I don't like Michael Vick for what he did.
Yeah.
The unfortunate thing is the race thing, too. You got to always, like, if it was Brett Favre, it'd be easier for me to just say fucking kill him or whatever.
Yeah.
But me and a friend of mine was talking about Michael Vick, and this stands for anybody in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Jail is so you don't have to be sorry. He's not sorry.
Wow.
He drowns dogs in buckets and has been doing it for years. He got out of jail. That was the time he had to pay for what he did. He shouldn't have to. He should come out and go, man, if I get my hands on another motherfucking dog, I'm going to drown his motherfucking ass in milk. Because milk is, I'm going to fucking shoot him in his face. He doesn't need to, because he's not sorry.
No.
But he paid whatever the price is.
You're right.
Gary Ridgway, the fucking Green River Killer, killed 50 hookers, 70 hookers. He got the rest of his life in jail. That's the non-apology time. Jail is so you don't apologize. If I was able to apologize, don't send me to fucking jail. I stabbed this guy. He died. I'm so fucking sorry. I didn't want him to die. I'm sorry. You don't need to send me to jail. I'm contrite, and I apologize now.
I like that point.
Don't fucking send me to jail if you need me to be sorry afterwards. That's what I'm saying. Stop with the, he has to be apologetic. This fucking guy, what's his name? Has lost his guy. He's going to lose. He can't drive. I think that's almost worse than doing time in prison.
Whoa, Dante?
Dante Stewart can't drive forever.
He doesn't. Oh, how long do they
forever?
No.
Yes.
No.
That's right. He's got enough money. He can actually hire someone to drive him.
But not, no. You know how much
You know how much that's a hassle after a while?
Well, of course it is, but it beats going to prison for 10
might be cool
years.
At first. New, like,
he's
oh,
a
cool,
fucking
I got driver,
football
but...
player. Football players aren't like basketball players.
Wait. Patrice, is that real, though? He's going to...
For the rest of his life, he can't drive.
What was his 30s
How's that possible?
Suspended, lifetime suspended driver's license.
He's in one state, though. In one
state. And he doesn't play this,
this
season.
There's no more one states anymore. When your license is suspended one place, the only reason it was like that before is because computers didn't exist.
Your
shit's suspended, it doesn't mean you can fucking drive in Massachusetts not drive in Kentucky.
That's true.
But he's rats.
How come he only got 30 days in jail then?
That was the deal, because he's Dante Stallworth, and he made a deal with the family.
The family
got bought off, so he hit somebody, whatever that could
be.
So he had to give the family whatever undisclosed amount, which is seven figures,
and
of course.
And never drive again.
Never drive again. He's on fucking probation for years. I don't know exactly how many years he's on probation. And then he gets suspended a year in the NFL. Next year, he should be able to just wear... You know, his sweatsuit should have Ciroc on it, Belvedere, or tequila. He should have anything he fucking wants because he's paying the price for sorry. This is what you pay when you In lieu of I'm sorry, his life is over.
You know, in corporate America, they don't hire people that are, you know, felons and whatnot, but in the NFL, they invite you right back.
Isn't that? But it's
and I don't care.
He can catch.
Huh? No, I know. You think the players on the opposing team are going to give him some big hits?
No, they're used to guys who do fucked up things. It's the NFL.
You don't think there's guys that are like animal lovers and there's Michael Vick and they're like, you know what? I'm gonna hit this guy a little.
It'll end up being very racial. But I don't like how the news portrays niggas as, like, we hate dogs, man. I hate that they portray. Every time they interview, hey, what you think of Michael? Man, it's a motherfucking dog, nigga. Drown that nigga. Motherfucker with a puppy head sandwich, like, nigga. Man, fuck that shit. And then they show what's going to be. Here's some more stuff he's going to do. 50,000 white women every football game with... dead baby seal faces.
Right.
They're gonna buy lump tickets
and
just annoy the fucker for the rest of his life.
Absolutely.
He paid the fucking price, even though I hate the fact that he had enough money to get a euthanasia machine. Like, he had enough money to buy one of those things that put animals to sleep peacefully.
That's fucked
up. As opposed to sleep. Look at,
why
don't
you pick another hobby?
He slammed them on the ground. He would pick them up by their chest and slam them on the ground, drown them in buckets, shoot him. Those that motherfucker was sadistic.
He's a complete piece of shit.
I do not condone what the fuck, but if you wanted to put him in jail for 20 years, that's the lieu of apology
of
time.
Apology.
They gave him the apology time, which was 2 fucking years.
We have the Stallworth sentence here. Served 24 days in a Miami-Dade jail as part of a plea agreement, which includes, here it is, 2 years of community control, and that's Florida's version of house arrest. 8 years of probation, drug and alcohol testing. So that's 8 years you can't even have a fucking drink. 1,000 hours of community service.
Holy shit. How many years is that?
What is 1,000 hours? How many years? That is 1,000 hours of on the side of the road,
it's 100,
picking up garbage.
It's just eight homeless
people.
It's 110-hour days.
Changing old people's diapers.
110-hour days.
Holy shit. And a lifetime suspension of his driver's license.
Jesus.
Stallworth also reached a multi-million dollar financial settlement with Reyes's family.
That means he wants to play again.
Is, you put that in a scale, and then you put I'm sorry on the other side, and it all equals out. That's it.
I'm fucking sorry.
That's it.
I did not. Listen, I drank. I did. I drank too much. I shouldn't have did that. I did not want to kill a man. I will pay his family. I don't want to put a price on this man's life, but I'll pay his family for what he would have brought to the table. Mm-hmm. And I'm fucking going to live with this for the rest of my life. Please don't do this.
Yeah.
I will not drink again. Yeah. He's not going to drink again any fucking way.
You don't think so?
Hell no.
It's liquor.
For 8 years, he can't. He's got
drug
and alcohol.
But for 8 years, he has to report to you, Anthony. Hi, how you doing? Hey, Dante. What's going on, buddy? Just looking in your face, angry, because there's going to be a white guy that goes, you just pissed away all your Negro future. You people, just some asshole who's working hard, some dog to bounty hunt a piece of garbage, who just goes, you people, you fucking people, you dirty motherfuckers. My nephew's a Polish soccer hooligan, and here you are, because you can catch a ball, you dreaded up Negro. Coon, and you fucking pissed it away. I'm gonna make your life miserable. You're not gonna get any special treatment here, stupid. And how are you gonna get home after you leave here?
Yeah, what are you gonna hitch?
You're gonna walk, bitch?
Grab a cab.
That's a nightmare.
That makes me want to go to jail, because this sometimes you go, I can get out of jail early. You could do a 3-year bid, or you could do a 1-year bid with 2-year probation.
Yeah.
I might want to do the whole 3, because then you're free from the confines of the state. This guy, I might want to do some time just so I can drive again.
Driving again
is just... I've never heard of anybody that can't drive ever again in their whole life.
He's got to, like, move to Spain or something and get a license there.
How do
like,
you...
somewhere else that's... in the world. He's got to move to Canada or Mexico.
It's a lot of time and not driving.
Did he have other drunk driving convictions?
No.
I guarantee this is not his first one.
No.
Because he killed a guy. Severity.
That's big.
Yeah, that's usually a 10-year...
That's big.
That's a big one.
Oof. I mean, he got out of jail.
Is a piece of shit.
I can't disagree, man.
He is a piece of fucking shit.
Why did he have to do that?
Knowing
he had so much to lose if he got caught.
Fuck him, man.
Smashing dogs and drowning dogs in buckets. And again, this is, it's not allegedly because he admitted it to it.
Yeah, that's what he did.
But the government put a pistol to your mouth and go, look it, man, because the government got a 98% conviction rate.
Yeah.
And if he fought the government, he fought the law and the law won, that motherfucker could have been doing big, big years. So it's possible that he could have just said, yeah, I did that. But he might not have been drowning dogs and shooting them, but he admitted to it. So I guess it's that he did it. That's what bothers me. If they're just like, oh, we found a machine that puts dogs to sleep, and they just, the losers are all bitten up, so we got to put them to sleep. But he slams dogs on the ground. Fuck can you do that to an animal, dude?
He's a piece of shit.
And look at its little chewed up face.
Suffering. I've been cursed with giving a shit about animals. It's a curse. It's not like, I wish I could just step right over a baby seal getting clubbed and go, hey,
hey, you're gonna make a nice jacket.
Shit, you should have took a left when you took a right there, buddy.
Jimmy, now that you know more, You think you should be playing again?
I still think that once you've done your jail, yes, because once you've done your jail time, they can't stop you from earning. I just hope that his fucking life is miserable.
It's not up to anyone's opinion now whether this guy should fucking be able to work.
I agree with you.
You could hate him. You could despise what he did. You could never fucking watch a game that he ever fucking plays in. Whatever. But he did his fucking time.
I agree.
Now he can fucking do whatever he needs to do.
I predict right now that he takes some horrendous hits. I'm telling you, there's going to be someone out there that is going to be like they're going to see him and they're going to go, you know what? I can't hold back.
Every NFL player will almost defend the fact that he fucked up, he paid the price. I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah.
Because most NFL players are dudes like that.
I'm with you, majority of the people. There's going to be a few. There's going to be a few out there that are going to be like, you know what? I can't let...
There are a few guys that are probably going to want to hurt him for that.
And try to be a hero for the...
Now, that's a very visceral reaction.
Oh, like, no, they're going to try to make it look clean. They're not going to, like, risk their own careers. But I'm telling you, there's going to be... I think you're feeling there's a few guys out there that have that anger right now.
They probably are, but I think for the most part, because you're going to get there before the grace of God go on. I best not fuck with him because I could be the next guy. But it's like us fucking shitting on radio guys when they get fired.
Now, he's sadistic.
No, they're going to be careful about it. I mean, when you line up against your opponent and he's a nice guy, you're hitting pretty damn hard.
Yeah, there's somebody
that's
going to want to hurt him for that.
I just have a feeling that it's not going to end pretty for Michael Vick this season.
Because some of those NFL guys are out of
And he's going to Philly?
Yeah. Well, we said it had to be a dirty team.
Yeah.
We said it.
What filthy fans.
We said there was a short list of teams that he could play for.
Nasty fans.
You know how many sad dog pictures are going to be in every Eagles game?
I know it. Sad. In Philly, dead dogs. They're
going to
swing around dead dogs and put those little things that go.
The party favors?
On that. Little puppies on a fucking.
Blow into a puppy tail.
His tongue flies out uncurled. It makes a whistle noise.
Are you fucking serious, man?
And do the Eagles play the Browns this year with the dog pound? I just got to see how that works.
With the bloody dog. It's going to be... Michael Vick is going to fucking
play the Browns?
Get it.
Usually?
They don't need to because they're in the AFC, but they might. They might.
Right. This is an outside chance. I don't know what's going
to be. Oh, the fans. The fucking
Philly fans. Oh. But if he gets in the game and takes over that asshole Donovan McNabb, who makes me more sick, and I know you guys don't follow football like that, but there's nothing more that I hate in the game than a black quarterback who won't run because he's trying to be smart like a white guy. So if they put Donovan on his fucking ass because he's trying to go, because he busted his knee years ago, and that was his big dream, so now he can't run, so he can prove to everybody, I'm smart like Peyton Manning. But if Peyton Manning and Tom Brady could run, they'll be like, these white guys, the weapons. The ultimate weapon. He's a weapon of mass destruction, Tom Brady. As soon as he sees a daylight, he's running. And everybody else, look at this dumb nigga. Can't throw. He just runs. I fucking hate black quarterbacks who won't run.
Yeah.
If he gets hit and Michael Vick comes in that motherfucker and takes the Eagles... to the Super Bowl?
How does that work?
Damn.
Everybody.
With all those
if I was a puppy,
sponsors.
I would never go to Philly because they'll just be killing dogs.
Dude, how?
Because Michael Vick don't like them.
Dude, all right.
It'll be a drowning dog celebration in the end zone. They'll hold up puppies. Touchdown, Michael Vick.
How about this scenario?
Spike a fucking shih tzu.
Yeah. Instead of Gatorade, they'll just pour a thing of dead wet dog on it.
If that fucker does well, we'll forget all about his fucking murderous.
Let's follow that scenario. Yeah. Michael Vick is now the quarterback of the Eagles, and they're in the Super Bowl, which is the biggest corporate fucking event in the world. How does that work out?
Oh, man.
Dave, how does that work out?
He just doesn't protest. Isn't
Michael Vick, you just won the Super Bowl. Where you going? Oh, nigga. We need some dogs I can kill. Doggy land, nigga. I can drown some puppies.
But you think Budweiser would be
absolutely.
All in?
Absolutely.
They
just
all
wouldn't
in.
Be in.
Super Bowl, Michael Vick is the quarterback.
Absolutely.
Budweiser's still all in.
And they would go, here's what Budweiser would do.
Really?
They would go, hey, look. You know, he paid his... They would say what everybody should be saying. Yeah. He paid his debt to society. He's very contrite. He's sorry Roger Goodell made the right. Boom. Mm-hmm. And Michael Vick will say, I really appreciate it. And he'll have a fucking Budweiser and drink it. But beer's a little bit more... like, they're not Procter & Gamble. Beer's a little more, like, testy. They'll do some testy shit like that.
Yeah, you get, like fucking tampon commercials during the...
Because he might even do a commercial where dogs are attacking him in some weird way or whatever. Like,
yeah, right.
Well, like, oh, shit.
Nah, no,
what are you saying?
You can never get away
from
that.
No, that's not a goofy commercial.
Jesus. And you just want us to listen to your thought?
He might do a commercial for what product?
What's wrong with you? Yeah, you're right, Patrice.
Hey, look, I'm not one to be stopped from making a dumb point. It was dumb as soon as you go, what the fuck? And as soon as I thought about it, like, hey, this is Michael Vick and some fucking big schnauzer's licking him in the face. And he goes, I'm sorry. And he drinks a Budweiser.
Yeah, that'll happen. That'll happen.
They bring Spuds McKenzie back just so he can shove his head in a bucket.
Of beer. He drowns dogs in buckets of beer. Hey, if you're going to drown, hey, which one of these beers is this animal? Does he like Coors Light or the... Oh, Schlitz.
Spuds McKenzie was Bud, right?
Yeah.
So, all right. So, if he gets a sponsorship with another beer company, yeah, why not drown
Spuds McKenzie?
Say, fuck him. Here's a Heineken or whatever the fuck.
Those sons of bitches, man. That motherfucker, all he's going to be able to make for the rest of his life. He's like Kramer. Kramer's finished.
Done.
For the rest of his life. Michael Vick is finished. At least Michael Vick. It's still got football he could play, but if it's like, oh, come out and put him on TV, and they ain't gonna fuck with him.
Nah, this is gonna be fun to watch.
Well, he's
I should say interesting to watch.
You're finishing the world.
That's all he was
looking for. Once you, I'm telling you, once you invade how visceral shit to white people, especially white women. Like, the nigga shit made white people look embarrassed and embarrassed white people with fucking Kramer, career over. If you notice, Michael Jackson's career was good up until white people didn't like him when he held that fucking kid over the balcony.
Over the balcony?
When he held that little white baby over the balcony, and white women said, this son of a bitch.
Little blanket.
It was a wrap. And he's fucking done. He is fucking... Michael Vick pissed off dog lovers. And I'm going to tell you, I love dogs, but I was at the Short Hills Mall, and I'm going to tell you how much white bitches love dogs. This funky bitch. I wish I had got a name because I say her name. She talked to my dog, because I brought my puppy to the Short Hills Mall, hanging around.
Yeah.
She talked to my fucking dog through me. And what's your name? And it's almost like she points, action, nigga. Gladys.
Oh, shit.
And how old are you? Come on, nigga, you can't talk. One. Good doggy. Look at this dog. Talking to my fucking dog and not me, that cunt.
What kind of dog you got?
A little poodle.
Aww.
It is a cute dog.
That's adorable.
No, I'm just surprised. I wouldn't think you would
What'd
have
you
a
think?
Poodle.
Well, it's for
my, I don't know if I would have said pit bull, but I would have said
I'm not
poodle.
Pit bulls scare me to death, man.
They're frightening,
They just don't look like lovable dogs. They look like they'll kill you.
Tyrannosaurus jaw on them and shit.
Like a fucking shark. A walking shark. That's they look like that.
Walking shark.
Like a big shark's head. And them devil eyes, but at the same time, my buddy, who's a pit bull guy? Pit bulls are loyal. They love. I'm a mutt fan. Mm. I got my girl wanted a dog where she can be like a white woman walking up the street and her kid. Yeah. You know, it's one of those little the toy dogs.
Yeah.
But that woman, you know, that woman, I was only there because my dog couldn't talk. She didn't even really go. She didn't have any bonding with me.
Interpreter.
Yeah.
I was interpreting for the dog.
Interpreter.
And what kind of dog is it? Come on, speak up, nigga! Quickly! I have no time to read its mind.
Shit.
That bitch. So he pissed them off. I'm sorry, man. He
That's fucking
he funny. Pissed that unforgiving fucking genre off, which is fucking white women that love animals, dude.
But and the difference like is, though, he doesn't rely on them for his living, though. That's the only thing he has going for him is he doesn't rely on them. He relies on guys.
Hold on. Ooh. We always got to pause to just look. Ooh. Brooklyn, get the fuck out of the way. There we go.
Ooh.
Don't look at
she stops the show in the
in
his tracks every morning. She works on the morning mashup, Nicole.
Mm-hmm.
Sirius Channel 1, I think.
All right, but that's my take on Vic, my
friend.
And
it's a great take, and we should replay that all week long while we're not here.
How about we just replay it the rest of the day and just go home now?
No shit. Well, we got to get into the Hannity stuff. Ant was on Hannity last night. We're going to do that after the break. Mm. We got Bobo's new bit.
Bobo's new bit.
And a lot of people beating up Super Agent Bob Eatman. I'll explain after the break.
Oh, really?
It's really funny, actually.
Oh, good. Look at this. I got to check that out.
Look at all these comments.
Oh,
pages and pages.
Holy shit.
Yeah. My videos get a little attention. Yeah. You put Super Agent Bob Eatman in a video and you get this. Look at this. Page after page
Nosferatu
of
comments and things like
that. I'm going to read some of the better ones after the break.
Hey, did that corpse leave town yet, or is he still here?
Back to Transylvania in a box full of dirt.
The fucking worst.
They said that we described him perfectly over the years. They finally get to see what he looks like. Hey, Patrice, you figure out your plug? I remember earlier in the week you were all messed up. So next week?
August 21st to the 23rd in Cleveland Improv.
Cleveland Improv.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I'm glad I came here because I would have been waiting at the airport. To go to Cleveland, right?
Fucking God bless that.
Wake up and
I'm
go
glad
see
Steve, Steve gave a shit before I did about the damn date.
You do well in Cleveland?
I've never been to Cleveland.
Holy
you
shit.
You haven't really?
I love you
This
in
is
Cleveland.
My first time in Cleveland, other than the virus.
Yeah, they'll love you.
Yeah, they're going to love you.
So that's a great time
for Patrice O'Neill for next weekend. Quick break. We'll continue. Opie and Anthony, Patrice O'Neill, and Jim Norton. Oh, Drew Boogie. Hold on. Drew, hit it. Vacation.
Yeah.
We'll be back, I don't know, end of the month. Taking 2 weeks this summer. That's nice. I like that.
Yeah, when are we back?
I don't know. What?
The 31st.
31st? All right, so we do one more day of radio this month.
When is Labor Day weekend?
The week after, so then we get a nice long weekend.
God damn, yo!
We set this one up nice, yo! Patrice O'Neill helping us out today. And I gotta say, yesterday after the show, we all went to breakfast, and
Is that a screen cap from your video cam?
Oh, fuck
yeah! Fucking really clear.
My HD Flip. I should work for HD Flip because I've sold a lot of motherfucking cameras for this company.
The Flip is an amazing little fucking gadget.
It's amazing,
and it picks up the audio pretty good.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, you're a little frustrated. You're not close enough to the audio source.
They figured it out. I was talking last night with some guy. We were talking about old camcorders and how you used to see people like at Disney with those giant fucking camcorders on their shoulder and how inconvenient it was. They'd be on rides and like have to hold the fucking thing in their lap or something or leave it somewhere because you couldn't take it on a ride with you. And now like every little thing has a fucking video camera in it. A pencil.
And you know the HD Flip, I have a feeling the next generation where you're going to be able to upload right from the motherfucker. How great would
you
that be?
Wireless to the net?
I have a feeling.
Yeah, that's the way. Wireless would be the way.
Without a doubt. That's the way it's going.
But also, once you got your groomsman?
Yeah.
Is it the HD or is it the regular?
How do you remember that?
I remember things.
Oh, nice.
I remember things.
That's for remembering my special occasion.
He didn't remember. I told him. He asked, what did I get for his groomsman? I told him the fucking thing.
I gave them all an HD Flip.
And, farty fucker. And they love him.
So listen.
All right.
So after the show yesterday, I made a video of our little breakfast. It's on my YouTube channel, Opie Radio. But I feel so bad for Super Agent Bob Eatman because I was excited to go, I should show everybody Bob Eatman. We've been beating him up for years. And I usually get maybe 20, 30 comments per video, maybe. Mm-hmm. This one's well over 100, and it's not stopping anytime soon. They are beating the shit out of Super Agent Bob Eatman in this video.
Bob.
And he's on film for maybe 5 seconds.
What you should
and the video is like 5 minutes long, I think.
What you should feel worse about is the fucking fat-faced, kind of like ass-cheek-necked idiot poking his fucking Casper head in. How creep. Like
oh,
a,
shit.
Like
I thought this video was about a buzzard swooping in to kill Bob Eatman. I'm sorry about that. That's you, no, you fucker.
The blubbery-necked apparition.
Just a few of the comments. Oh, my God, even Super Agent Bob Eatman looks like he's doom and gloom. Look how pale and undead he looks. Bobby is cute, though. That ghoul fucking Eatman. And I bet Bob didn't pay either. It just goes on and on. Holy shit, maybe Ann could help me out with this one. Eatman is G-Man from Half-Life.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Or, holy shit, he really is.
Or a retarded Gregory Peck.
AG1247 writes, wow, you guys don't lie when you say he's a ghoul. Coke Logic, I'm shocked to see Bob Eatman doesn't burst into flames in the sunlight. Mr. Kenji writes, Michael Jackson has been dead for a month and a half, and he still looks better and has more color than Super Agent Bob Eatman.
How about Bob Dole?
little Dole in him too,
yeah. He looks like Dole's arm.
Beta 2G, no wonder Bob Eatman has never been on camera. This guy writes, Eatman looks like the vampire from the Bugs Bunny cartoon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Eatman looks like he came from Dark Shadows. Fancy wow. people eating all by themselves. Super Agent Bob Eatman looks like he's holding kryptonite. He's the Walking Dead. It just goes on and on and on. He needs follicles. What happened to Eatman's upper lip? Looks like a burn victim. That's Wrathchild 11.
Just being horrible.
Someone should tell Eatman that it's too early to have on his Boris Karloff makeup. I don't know.
Is there any audio of him talking? He said, like, hi to the camera.
How the fuck can you eat with that zombie Bob Eatman at your table?
Wow.
Congrats on you and Ant describing Bob Eatman perfectly throughout the years. Scary.
He ordered brains.
Jeez. Yeah, back up the video slightly, and you get to hear Bob Eatman talk.
He is good. A monumental dud.
Hello!
Bella.
Here's Bob Eatman.
Sir?
Oh, it's after that. I got the waiter with a sir. Oh, no. All right. You got it.
By the way,
you don't have to watch the whole video.
Watch the video because the Bob Kelly fucking with Club Soda Kenny's crotch.
Oh, right.
Because
right.
He has what but Bob Kelly calls teacher cock.
Yeah.
Yeah, teacher cock. It's when you sit down and your pants kind of fold in the front. You know where you how your fly kind of folds in the front and makes it look like you almost have a boner?
Yeah, it's pants boner.
I know.
Pants boner. Comes
pants
up all the,
boner. Yeah,
pants boner. Right.
Yeah, pants boner.
He starts squeezing it and hitting it.
Yeah, Bob Kelly was squeezing it and pushing down on it. And Kenny's just sitting there.
Yeah.
There's a monster on the screen.
Oh, Jimmy.
Oh, Jimmy.
Jesus, right. Renfield. Just swapping a spider suit.
Push play so we get to hear Bobby Eatman.
Jimmy Comet.
Hot at the end.
Here it is. Watch.
Oh, this is Super Agent Bob Eatman. First time on camera ever.
Whoa. This is hella charisma. Makes love
for
the camera.
That's all he did was a hello.
Hello.
And he's getting beat up. He was on camera, like I said, 10 or 15 seconds.
I love the fact that Bob tried to talk. If rewind Bob's part again today, because you see Bob about to say hello, and he didn't want to blow his cue. Watch Bob. He doesn't even know when to say hello. He goes to say hello, then he lets you finish.
When to say hello. Yeah.
Just yeah. Watch it.
He's strong, isn't he?
Oh, this is Super Agent Bob Eatman. First time on camera.
You see him gear up to say hello.
He blew his hello.
His little hitchhiker.
Yeah, because then Opie said first time on camera.
Yeah.
So I threw him for a loop.
I threw off
a
natural fool.
And then look at Jimmy's stupid hat. Fucking bowl that he's eating his soup from.
Yeah, I didn't film that, unfortunately.
I saw a clip of it.
It looked like a derby hat?
A little derby hat.
Yeah.
And he's...
No!
I was eating...
nice freeze frame.
There's some really amazing freeze frames of me available in this from the side.
Oh. Are you Holy throwing up on the food first? Oh, it's just a grossness.
Dude, there are some fucking freeze frames of the kid.
Holy shit, it does look like it.
It really does look like I'm vomiting on my phone.
Oh, fucking goddamn. Oh.
It's Brundle Jim.
This video turned out pretty well. It's on my YouTube channel, OP Radio. Even though we're going on vacation, I'm going to be videoing my ass off. Ant's going to be doing his thing that we don't talk about much, but we're not really going away the next 2 weeks.
Just
I'm doing
a staycation.
Crab and corn.
Are you guys just having lunch or?
Yeah,
a little breakfast. Yeah.
Where is this place?
This place rules. It's close.
Yeah.
Shh. Ixnay on the Ole Asian K.
It's our spot.
Is it really?
Oh, God. It could be the coolest spot in all of New York City.
Yeah. What kind of food?
We're freeze framing. We're going frame by frame watching Jimmy eat.
Oh.
And right now, his mouth is opening like a fucking stroke victim.
Are you sticking your tongue out to touch the food first?
So I don't know.
Bad.
It's weird because you're eating soup.
You're like,
just take your mouth and go.
Oh, God. Look at this.
Wait a minute, but it was serious. You thought he was playing, but look at this.
No, I wasn't playing.
Eating video. Oh, he's like the senator from the, he's like the senator from the X-Men. Yeah, fucking mollusk.
Oh God.
There is nothing better than framing and timing this video as Jimmy is eating. You'll never eat again.
Oh, look at
this. Look what's gonna drip into the bowl off his lip.
Oh, just look at this.
It's a crab soup. It's a crab and corn chowder.
Crab eating it.
Yes.
There's gonna be some freeze framing to this
dude,
video.
Holy shit.
Maybe Jimmy's the star of the video after all.
Oh!
What are you doing?
Holy shit.
Oh.
It's like sliced alone with Bell's palsy.
Oh my God, look at you.
I'm eating soup.
Oh my God.
Oh God damn, that is fucking funny.
Oh, poor thing.
Poor thing.
It's like the end of Terms of Endearment.
Michael Vick would have drowned you.
He was drowning himself.
Oh, fucking my other
side. And then you got the waiter who's happy to be there, too happy to be there. And
look at that face.
Too much going on in this video.
Another huge spoonful of goodness.
Oh, there really was delicious.
You was there too, him?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I was right next to
him. Okay.
Yeah, he
makes an appearance later in the video.
I'm laughing now.
Actually, the magic of video, we started the video without Anthony there, and then Anthony showed up. Look at this. Just pushing on.
What the fuck is wrong with Bobby, man?
Kelly just pushing on Clint Kenny's penis.
The way my nose points down, I am awful from the side.
That is one of your best fucking videos.
I like
just
this one.
Slow-mo and... Oh, very fun.
That is very fun. That is
more
truly
Jimmy
terrible.
Eating.
OP Radio on YouTube. Let's move on to Anthony's appearance on show.
Just please take Jimmy frame by frame on that video.
That.
You'll laugh your balls off.
Wait, 2:35 on YouTube. 2 minutes, 35 seconds is when you see Jimmy's sickness.
Go in 2 minutes, 35 seconds, and then just frame
soup.
One frame at a time.
You could probably get 10 to 20 good shots.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Something tells me that they're going to poke fun at me.
I think there might be some photoshopping and just some
They wouldn't have
things.
The guts. They wouldn't dare mock me eating.
They're going to forget about Bob Eatman really quickly.
God damn, that's funny.
The comments are just ridiculous on that one. All right, so we started the show with somebody saying that some liberal guy on Sean Hannity beat the shit out of you.
And it
we
wasn't
got the
even
proof
the case.
That that's not true,
I
right?
fucking nailed the guy. Every comment from everybody that watched it said I just shut him down.
Yeah.
Shut him right down.
Yeah.
Hey.
Let's get into this. We got a couple clips of Anthony on Hannity. Hannity intros Anthony.
Uh-oh.
And he is the co-host of the ever-popular Opie and Anthony show, which broadcasts on Sirius XM satellite radio. Anthony Cumia is here. What's up with the bedwetting Obama-supporting liberal co-host of yours? Why isn't he here?
What a fucking asshole.
Wow. bedwetting.
He's certainly...
Yeah, that's me. Like, I care enough to be that.
Bedwetting.
Bedwetting liberal. That's always a fun one, bedwetting liberal.
What is that?
They're just always pissing themselves in their beds.
Why isn't he here?
Oh, Obi? I should throw, like, a Hillary hissy fit and say, it's about me, I'm here, talk about me.
Yeah, you're probably...
But, no, I think you just answered your own question. That's why he's not here.
Oh, he doesn't... Because he admits that he voted for Obama. He doesn't want to admit it anymore.
Well,
didn't vote for Obama, Sean. You know that. I'm going to stop the tape every second.
You didn't.
I didn't
he
vote.
He wants you on that show so fucking bad.
And I openly said I didn't vote.
But that would be funny, though. If he said you voted for Obama and you know that, you'd go, no, I don't vote.
All right, maybe I got an angle now.
Maybe you got an angle.
Call him out on his lies.
Voting's easy.
And by the way, George Carlin has the greatest reason not to vote.
Thank you. Yes, that's what we bring up all the time.
Greatest bits ever. Like, just, I will not vote. Because then if you vote, you can't
complain.
You can't complain.
You're part of the problem.
Yes, I don't vote, so I can... I don't like none of these pieces of shit, so I can complain.
George was the master at taking the most obvious thing that nobody else saw. And he took that argument people have been having for 50 years about voting, and he made it fucking
made
funny and original.
Made you feel not guilty about voting. You just go, I could...
No one ever had an answer to that. It's like, well, if you don't vote, you can't. Then you can't complain about the
you can complain if you don't vote.
That's why I can complain, because I didn't vote.
That is great.
Oh, shit.
Not that that's the right message to send. Guy that ruins every moment with trying to be serious.
Because he admits that he voted for Obama. He doesn't want to admit it anymore.
Well, yeah, he...
Hey, did I vote for Obama?
I would like...
I want to be on record and say I did not vote. I haven't voted for a president in a long time.
I think you might be literal on that, though.
He's
saying you are a supporter. Yeah. It doesn't matter.
He's trying to coax you and bait you onto the show.
I'm not as rah-rah as far as Obama goes. That's for sure.
Oh, really?
Maybe that's what he's saying.
I want to hear the tapes of you going, Obama!
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
That is true. You did yell Obama.
I've changed a little bit.
It's cocaine!
Cocaine! No, I just... new boss, same as the old boss.
Well, not quite.
I like Obama a lot more than I would have liked
new
Sarah
boss,
Palin.
Same as the old boss.
Man, really.
I like him more than I would have liked some of them.
High five. Air high five. Yes.
Well, yeah, he brought in by the whole change thing, and this is going to be great. It's going to be a different thing. And then business as usual, tax and spend Democrat, and he can't really defend himself. So,
well, thank God he's got you and Norton to straighten him out.
We like straighten that out. I like getting feedback, too, on the show when I talk about things like that, where one guy will say, oh, my God, you're a conservative, right-wing, radical, and then the next one will be like, I agree with you 100%.
You're more libertarian. I'm more like a Christian conservative.
Because I do have a few views that kind of drift over. Not, I never want to say left, but a little more center.
Kind of drift. You're for gay marriage. That's a fucking pogo leap from the Christian right.
Well, it is. I'm not. You know what it is, though? I'm not for gay marriage.
We don't
care.
I
could give a flying fuck about gay marriage. Is what it is.
You are a
asshole.
You are a logical, reasonable racist.
Thank you.
That's what
I like
is.
To be. I like to
an intelligent
like
racist.
I'm going to run on that platform.
You can't get past
I have
black
preconceived
and
notions that I have a very hard time disposing of.
Yeah.
But yet every time I am friendly with ethnically diverse people, I never have a problem with people I'm friendly with.
Them,
I'm very friendly with you, Patrice O'Neill.
I become
my Negro friend.
We become us as opposed to them when you meet. Yeah.
Drew Boogie. I am friendly with Drew Boogie.
But you don't even know what Drew Boogie's nationality is.
No one does. No one does.
Look at Drew was a thing.
He's
If we're friends with Drew, we're all friends with something else.
Yeah,
something else. Don't know.
He's black and Dominican. He's got like a thin Dominican mustache.
If I had
a
guess, I would say
like
there's some Asian in there.
Exactly. Something.
There's some Asian.
Mendoza.
Asian? Asian?
There was some cottage rape going on during this. There was some... The father from the Brady Bunch was tiptoeing in.
Ed Asner hopped off the boat and did a little fucking...
There was some funny shit going on in Drew's family.
What are you?
I'm Jamaican, but my parents are mixed. There's a lot of mixing going on back there.
Do you speak patois?
Yeah.
Really? How do you speak that?
I kind of don't. Sorry.
We call him out.
Sorry to disappoint you, Jimmy.
That's all right.
Yeah, because what do you got? Like hazel eyes or something?
Yeah. There's some...
Azel. Azel.
Without the H.
Azel. Azel Heise.
It goes on before the E.
Yeah, they skip the H sometimes.
Def Jam, but Azel Heise.
My name is right. Drew Boogie.
I love Jamaican Jimmy.
Du Bois and Bonte Man. The blood clot pretty baby.
Boo.
The Jamaicans always suck their teeth, too.
Yeah?
They're always miserable.
What's that all about?
It's true.
I don't even know what that's about.
He must.
It's true, though.
And you learn all of that from them fucking Jamaican bitches that's pushing around these white babies around Manhattan.
Yeah.
He just watching them do their fucking thing. Sucking their teeth. But he's digging in your ass, oh.
Huh?
Well, man, he wants a piece of you.
That's all right.
Whatever.
He wants a piece of you.
I don't have passion for the fight.
He wants you on the show. He really does.
I want to talk sports or something else. I don't...
Right, the old same old, same old. But by this time, Anthony, you must know it's the old same old. It's just the same old, same old.
Well, you know how I prepped for the show? I sat there and watched Fox News and all the other shows for about 2 hours. Glenn Beck and stuff like that, and then
just repeated stuff.
And then what's his name? Fucking Bill O'Reilly. And then I'm like, all right,
sound bites, man.
I'll just repeat that.
Hannity banned me from his show. He don't want to talk to me no more since Kramer and them.
Oh well.
Well, you had one of them. Was it on Hannity?
No, it was a woman. It was John Gibson. But
yeah, Gibson.
I got a good one. Some good ones.
You pretty much wrecked John Gibson's TV career with that one. You know that, right?
Nah, they
I haven't seen him back since.
Oh, he's
funny
gone.
On Hannity, though. You were very funny.
Yeah, I was good on Hannity. Yeah, you were good on Hannity. And I laugh at him because he always tries to make you. The black people always got to come in and be the. Like, if he had me on for Michael Vick, he would have fucking had me on to be the guy that goes, like, white people don't understand. Like, I couldn't have that view. He would have been like, what good are you? I need a...
We have to play this.
Oh, yeah.
Radio Crackdown, Patrice O'Neill. Just find where it starts there, Danny, for me, please. This is one of my favorite Patrice O'Neill things ever.
I love this one.
He fucking put this woman...
She was the worst.
...in her place so bad. They're talking about Radio Crackdown. Was this the Imus thing?
No, this is O'Neill.
This is you. They were trying to get rid of you.
They're talking about fucking Homeless
Charlie?
Yeah.
But also they're talking about Elvis... No, Jesus, JB and Elvis, too.
And I was mad at her because she was sitting there, and this was behind, this was from me watching what she was doing. She wouldn't speak to me, Sonia Osorio. She wouldn't speak to me, but she...
Was she from now?
Yeah, naturalization woman.
Yep.
And she was like, fire them. And I was like, you fucking bitch. You just like fire people. Have them fired.
Yeah.
Like,
just flick.
Didn't even care. Just her position was her position. Yeah. What a fucking ass.
Yeah,
just,
she sucks.
Just to bring everyone to the table, Homeless Charlie made some crazy, you know...
Funny remark. Can we play that again? Can we play that?
We should be able to.
Let's fucking play Homeless Charlie, for Christ's sake.
And the thing about that, he never said anything.
We never...
He never said anything towards them.
No.
I listened to that fucking thing.
No, I know.
Isn't he a
funny dude, man? He was a naturally funny guy.
Funny homeless guy.
A funny fucking homeless dude.
Saying stuff about the First Lady and...
That Bush bitch.
He called
Condoleezza Rice the Bush bitch.
Yeah.
He was funny.
And pretty much we were observers just watching Homeless Charlie do his thing.
Fuck the Queen of England.
We've never seen Homeless Charlie since, by the way. We used to see him on the streets of New York. We haven't seen him since.
Fucking black van pulled up and threw him in.
I think he got a case of the food poisoning.
Yeah.
That food poisoning.
It's somewhere.
I think we got orders to nuke all copies of that audio.
It's somewhere. That was when the merger was going through.
It's got to be somewhere.
You know how stupid that statement is when there's probably another... 100 to 200 copies out there.
Nowadays,
the
old Tonight Show.
The Nixon tapes. Watergate, motherfucker. Can't burn tapes no more.
No, the old honeymooners. The honeymooners where they lost tapes. A few episodes because they didn't think anyone wanted to see this shit 30, 40 years later.
They recorded over stuff.
Right.
What is that?
How stupid is that? We had to destroy old copies, and there's hundreds of other copies out there.
Silly.
What are you going to start knocking on listeners' doors?
Who is that Bush bitch?
What did that accomplish in the end?
That Charlie made me fucking laugh, man.
I'm just saying, there it is.
Yeah, there's the Patrice thing. So we got Patrice O'Neill. When that whole thing went down, he was invited to go on Fox and listen to what he does to this woman.
With me now, New City President Sonia Osorio. She took part in a recent protest calling for radio stations to stop supporting negative language in music and talk radio, and also our favorite stand-up comic, Patrice O'Neill. Oh,
thank you, sir.
Patrice, are ONA next?
I hope not. I hope JV, I wish JV and Elvis didn't lose their job or Imus. It's funny. This is the thing. I don't know her, but I'm assuming that she has nothing to do with funny. So I'm going to speak as the expert on funny. Funny people should just be left to trying to be funny.
What if they're not funny?
Then you made a mistake. But how many times has unfunny rape jokes lead to rape? Like,
I don't know how many jokes about rape there are.
There's a lot. But your world is not funny. Your world is next on the big story. My world is people trying to be funny.
Well, I mean, you think it's okay to try to make jokes about rape?
I'm diabetic. I make fun of that. I'm a victim. I might lose a toe. But I'm trying to make fun of it. I'm trying to make fun of anything I think I can make fun of.
Sonia?
You know, what's happening now is the marketplace is deciding what's appropriate or what's not appropriate. I think the nation is just tired. There's a new mood in the nation.
Oh, wait, pause that for one second. This is why you gotta hate women like this. The marketplace decides what's appropriate. So how about if the marketplace dictates that women should make less money, you dopey bitch? Is that appropriate?
Yeah.
Or should what is quote-unquote right rise above what the fucking marketplace dictates?
And if the marketplace dictated it, it would show in the ratings, and then they would fire you for low ratings.
Right.
The marketplace is gauged in radio and television by ratings. So if it's a high-rated show, but they're saying shit you don't like.
But just speaking in logic, though.
Yeah, yeah.
This is what no one does ever. It's not allowed anywhere. That you make a logical point.
No,
she's not being logical. She's just being horrible.
She's being a representative.
She's being what she
now.
Is. Yeah,
God forbid. God forbid the head of New York's president of Now would come out and go, "I found the comments disgusting." But you know what? In a free society, you're going to hear things that are unpleasant to hear. As long as they're not seriously advocating rape or violence against women, I have no problem with it. God forbid a fucking liberal would ever.
Never.
Or a conservative, for that matter, never. Have that take on it.
Don't be too upset, because Patrice really.
Oh, he destroyed her.
He really puts her in her place.
Oh, my God, yes.
And is it true that Angela Yee is pissed off about our Marion Barry stuff last week? How do you know, Patrice? They're saying that's Patrice.
I didn't want to get in the middle of this, but I wouldn't say
who is she.
She runs the morning show at the Black station.
I know why she's mad,
but she's I told her when I was on the radio, the Marion Barry thing.
We dragged them in and we had
that was a issue.
Why?
It was an issue.
That was their scheduled time, and I think it took away from
a few things. Is
okay, well,
I apologize for that. I told her that was as simple as 1, 2, 3.
I thought she was mad because we had her guest after she did.
Somebody said a comment. This is now that I'm talking.
Go.
The comment was, come over to here, and this is supposedly come over here. Don't you want to have more people listen to
him? I said that to him.
All right,
I said I didn't say blow off any show. I said we have the biggest audience on the platform right now that you can hear. And then he decided to come in for a minute. I didn't drag him in. That was the truth.
Let's get the facts out. We said that not knowing that he was just on her show. We had no idea what show Marion Barry
was
doing.
That's what no one knows. We weren't taking a shot at her.
We don't even know her.
Yeah, exactly.
No. I actually wasn't taking a shot at her at all. I didn't know where he was scheduled because a lot of times these people can come through.
And I told her to come say something. Just say, it's not going to be a radio war. It's just like, I know they didn't just disrespect the thing. But the thing is, what she's upset about is that, everything is racially divided. It's not you guys. It's that when they... when they have to get people to sign in over there, it has to be 4 or 5 days. They have to do a record check, because it's possible a mass murderer could just walk up in there.
Yeah, we're
and
not
the
happy.
White shows could just be like, somebody's coming up. Yeah. Now!
we're not happy that we broadcast so close to their studio. We so watched the Hot 97 shit that used to go down.
You know, there's some things, you know, but it could be squashed.
I said that.
With immediate.
Patrice. I said that, but it wasn't in the vein of fuck Shade 45. We actually like Shade 45. It simply was.
We have Woo Kid.
We have the biggest
Woo
audience.
Kid on all the time.
At least Woo Kid, next to Howard, we have the biggest audience that he would have got on. So it was like, why wouldn't you come on? And then a minute later, he came in. I didn't force him to come in.
Right, but you didn't. Do you see what a misunderstanding is? And then it goes from the top down. But I'm like, y'all are neighbors. I mean, fucking Sharon, like Hammer went from here right over there. It's just just fucking is what it
and
is.
And you went from here to there.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. I'm just like,
dude, it's over.
He's a politician. Yeah. That's how you get him
on. And if we took time away from her time, then yeah, we're wrong. So that's it.
There you go.
Let's get back to Patrice giving this woman a beating.
That's not appropriate. I think the nation is just tired. There's a new mood in the nation.
What nation?
The nation. You know what? We're tired of things that are just
the nation, this paper, and you. I'm not the nation. I'm just speaking for me and funny. You're speaking for the nation, or you're speaking for...
Yeah, you know why? Because I remember 6 years ago...
Why is Man Cow on?
...doing something against Anthony Openy because they were just so outrageous, and their violent images they put out to women was just... uncalled for. And now I think people...
You think they were trying to be funny?
I think now people in this country...
Do you think they were trying to be funny?
Tired. You know what? I don't care if they're trying to be funny.
That's what I'm saying. Why are you in that business?
I've been to your show once, and it wasn't very funny being a woman.
It was hilarious.
When you talked about...
That's why she doesn't like me. I was in the paper with her, and the joke is hilarious. It's called The Angry Pirate. And the lady who wrote it in her outrage didn't even know what it meant. And anybody who read it laughed because they know what's funny. You're not living in the context of funny. You're living in the context of fire.
They have every right to be as funny as they want.
Oh, really?
They can go out and try to be as funny as they want, make as much money being as funny as they want. This is what's happening. There is a change in this country. People are realizing they have an opportunity to speak out, and advertisers are listening.
You're not talking to who I talk to.
And you're not going to get paid as much money anymore.
Sonia and Patrice, look at this.
That's what it is. The marketplace
CBS radio firings. They've been on a tear lately.
All right.
Are they cleaning house, or is this the PC cops run amok?
You know what it is, John. You know what it is while you're reading that paper. It's the PC cops run amok.
Well, you think she's the PC cop?
Of course she is. She has an entire encyclopedia of her stance on it, but it's no passion involved. It's not a real... This is just what she has to say. We are outraged and fired. Name calling. I'm outraged. I am outraged.
You should be outraged.
I am a fool. Now, if I called you a fool...
You know what? People are a new sense of entitlement.
Who are these people
in this country?
Who are the people?
A new sense of entitlement. Here's
my question. How can you justify a bad joke, a joke that isn't funny? Oh, wait a minute.
Go ahead.
An attempt that isn't funny, doesn't get any laughs, and is about raping the first black woman to ever become the Secretary of State of the United States.
She's black, dude.
Well, why not?
The attempt... is what I'm trying to fight for. The joke may or may... Funny jokes and unfunny jokes are come out of the same birth. That you don't know if anything is going to be funny. You should attempt to be able to make anything funny.
Don't you think a joke about rape is doomed to be not funny?
It's possible, but I've heard them.
You heard a funny rape joke?
No.
I say a couple. Watch my HBO special. I'm pretty good at it.
The truth says that if you're having sex with a woman, doggy style, and if you
hit her in the head
just the right time.
No, it's ejaculate in her eye and kick her in the shin, and she walks around like, arg! That's what she was trying to say.
A violent act of hitting her in the back of her head, her body.
It's called the donkey punch.
Which will then.
Why are you laughing? She's outraged. It's called the donkey punch. It's called humor that she has no clue what it is.
You have the same problem that Opie and Anthony does. You can't say just anything on the air.
You can say anything you want. It might not be funny. You might get in trouble for it, but you should be able to be attempting. And plus, when is a crazy bum going to get an opportunity to rape the president? If the president's wife, John? It was trying to be funny.
All right, Patrice, why aren't I hearing Al Sharpton complain about this thing involving Congress?
Because it wasn't involving young black women.
Well, it's involving a very prominent black woman.
Well, where was she during young black? Everybody has their agenda.
I was there.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, why am I not hearing from Sharpton?
Because it doesn't concern him. It's not concerning him. It's black. It's, you know, come on now. You know, Al Sharpton has his agenda, and it was perfect for Al. Young black women. And now she's representing just women in general. She's not representing the nappy hoe part. She's representing the just the hoe. The nappy-headed part, she has nothing to do with. Just the hoe.
Sonia?
You know what? Women have been abused publicly in the media for too long, and people are tired of it. This has been a beautiful response of just the general public saying to advertisers, we're your consumers.
No,
we don't want to have to avoid everything in the street. We don't want to have to worry about what radio station we turn on. And there is some really derogatory, violent thing to deal with.
All your information, ma'am, is secondhand from someone making you aware that someone may have said something that you should be upset about. It's a shame. Your constituency, the people you represent aren't all victims in this matter.
Teresa O'Neill, thank you very much. Sonia Osorio, thanks to both of you. Appreciate it. Time for big politics.
Kick that dumb bitch.
That was John Gibson going, holy shit,
I
think I'm in trouble.
I can't believe you shit the angry pirate.
And you know what John, you know what John said to me? He said, I have to apologize for what I did to her. And because he knew what I was going to do to her.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he said, man, I had to apologize to her for he set her up.
Oh, fuck.
To be.
Yeah.
He just was victim. Enjoying.
Of course he was.
Just how ridiculous she was sounding.
That fucking.
You killed
just
her.
Unfunny. Over the time. Do you think. I can never picture. A woman like that with her fucking legs pinned back, just getting
slammed, absolutely, I can too.
Like, yeah, fuck me.
She turned me on that goddamn bitch.
Yeah, she's sexy.
She was pretty hot.
I think when she's not on TV, that's exactly what's going on.
You think she likes being smacked?
I think
her hair
so. Dude, I put money on it.
Yeah,
money on it.
Come on her.
And the thing is, she laughed a couple of times too. She just really fell apart.
Dude, you were arguing what the angry pirate is all about.
That's so funny.
On Fox News.
No, that's the Donkey Punch.
Do you understand how amazing? That will never be done again.
Oh, I haven't been on there since.
No.
I haven't seen Fox News since. Handy would throw me on a bone every couple of times. It was a wrap after John
That's
Gibson had to apologize
That's
the next day.
Bad. You would give him great TV every time out, man.
They got
go. You got to play by their rules, though. If you don't play by their rules, you're out.
That is some good shit.
Let's get back to Anthony on Sean Hannity from last night. And starts going after the liberal guy. This is what the caller brought
Jimmy.
Up a couple hours ago.
Oh, God, Jimmy. Yeah.
Okay.
The insurance reforms, the cost spending, all those things that people are concerned about, they want addressed. They may not want everything that's in the House bill, but they want health reform, and they want it now.
Government, government health care. That is restructuring perhaps insurance companies, pharmaceuticals. I'm for that. I think that should be looked at.
Government health care is a talking point. There's not anybody talking
about it.
The government is not taking over anything.
That was an election. That was a campaign promise.
By whom?
By Barack Obama.
That we're going to give you government health care. No,
let me quote him. He said that he wanted to get rid of, in 2007, the employee benefit system if it takes 10, 15, or 20 years. And
he's a
and he wanted a single payer system.
See, he said he was trying to say that health care reform was a talking point. It's like, no, dummy. That was his whole fucking platform.
People hate Hannity because he always had a fact. It's like, there's nothing worse than arguing with somebody that has facts and dates. When someone says, look, in April of, you're like, ah, fuck off.
It's one of the things that makes me, I seriously daydream when I'm on there just tapping him on the shoulder and go, what is that? Take all his stupid papers and throw them and have him have a regular conversation. He has a pile of papers and weaponry. When you come in, it's always a knife and a gunfight. You can't come more prepared than Sean Hannity.
Exactly. That's a good thing.
Here's you, Anthony, farting. What do you have to say about that?
Well, that's my job.
I fart.
You're on the show.
It's ridiculous. I've never seen him just have a goddamn
you know what he actually,
regular human conversation, man.
You know what he did last night at one point, which was just like, I don't know how he did this. talking about the bill, which the health care bill, which is probably over 1,000 pages long. And he goes, somebody brought something up, and he goes, no, page 16, that says blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, he fucking picked out page 16.
It's horrifying.
And knew what the fuck was on it.
Why do you think the average citizen is finished? Why do you think we're done? It's it's these HR things, whatever they call it, House of Representatives, 1306.
Yeah,
it's they're 1,000 pages long. What's the bill? The goddamn $787 billion
the stimulus package.
It's fucking 1,200 pages long.
Yeah,
and they didn't give them a day to read it. They just said this is it, just sign it, and it's fucking shocking. But this shit is weaponry. He'll come to these fucking things, and this guy has a pile of papers, and he just says a statement. You're saying that it is sound bites, and you're flustered. You're like, well, give me 2 minutes to get a thought together.
You know what's fucking amazing? The original like Bill of Rights is like a page. It's one page.
I got a booklet.
Here it is. Bill of Rights. And then it turns into multi-thousand page legalese bullshit that no one could understand.
Lawyers.
No one reads through. It's signed on party lines. Oh, who wrote it? A Democrat? I don't have to read it. Then I'll just sign it if I'm a Democrat. And if I'm a Republican, I won't sign off on it.
Well, we're at the last stages of all these plans anyway, because they're going after white folks.
Yeah.
Now that white folks are getting involved with this,
this
anti-government thing,
the fucking town hall meetings,
gonna hit the fucking fan now.
Yeah, all the networks, CBS, NBC, MSNBC, they're treating these town hall things like fucking Klan meetings and Nazis. They're saying that they're using these tactics of political terrorism. They call it
such scumbags.
And you know why? Because it's a different face of the people that are protesting. It's fucking middle class white people.
And
holy shit.
Here's
they finally
where
got off their ass
black
and
people
went to protest.
This is where we all should be coming together, but we don't.
No.
Because
you guys come together and protest.
We come together, but this is a people problem.
Flames and TVs
why black people are going to sit back and watch what black people have been complaining about.
Uh-huh.
Middle class white folks who are now becoming poor and scared, saying the same thing that black people have been saying for years, but we all should be together, because I'm going to tell you, the militia, the people in the mountains, they're the closest to thinking like the people who made the Bill of Rights in the Constitution. They're really the anti-tax, the anti-government in your life. Because conservative and liberal, I don't know where it's turned into this white, black, and this poor. Conservative is just supposed to be people who don't like a lot of government.
Right.
Who don't like a lot of bullshit in their government. These people in the hills that they're now going to, they're making the terrorists. They're not talking about fucking, first of all, Iraq don't exist more in the news.
What happened there?
Now it's Afghanistan, and now the war on terror is here, the white militia groups who won't pay taxes and will fight. But black people need to be on their side, too, supporting them, the guns and everything else. But they split us down the middle, and if these fuckers stop saying hate niggas and hate Jews and hate Puerto Ricans, as a people, we can be together. But the fact is, some of their shit is they hate me. But I'm like, I'm on your side, you fucking goofy bastard. I'm saying you should live free. Because somebody said something one time about democracy. Democracy is not freedom. Democracy is 51% of the people control 49% of the people. Mm-hmm. Essentially, it's, as they say, two wolves and a sheep voting for dinner. Voting for what's for dinner. That's what democracy is. It's not really free.
But technically, we are a representative republic. We are not a democracy. So
one of Norton's farts for that.
You want one?
Oh,
this
shit.
Is fart born.
Give me a second.
Because look, man, the fucking militia, I see it, what's going on, as they call a big sister now. They call her because the lady that for some bitch runs the some woman.
My phone taps and shit.
Some lovely woman runs the fucking whatever the security, and now the biggest thing is these Timothy McVeigh motherfuckers,
and these
crazy guys, and so now we got to watch them.
But
they're not really bothering anybody. They're up in the hills doing goofy shit like shooting targets of me instead of just saying to people, look, we're sorry, black people, you're not paranoid, you're not fucking assholes, now it's hitting us, and we apologize for all the shit that we called you paranoid for, now it's coming down on us, and when we fix it, then you can go back to being niggas, and we can go back to being crackers, and don't like each other, because that's the way we are. But right now, you know, right now, we got to be together on this one, man. I'm telling you. But we're not.
There's a huge intrusion of government right now that is really, it's the beginning of it.
And white arrogance is what's making it step up, along with
white arrogance.
The arrogance of white people to say, what the, who the, and when I say white, not skin, just the institution of why, this is preposterous, when now cops are fucking black. White people are talking about martial law and police brutality, and they're talking about the government intruding. They're having their homes taken. They're having just complete disrespect. Well, now white people are dealing with it. Now it's an issue.
Well, when the White House puts out statements like, if you see anything fishy about the healthcare reform facts, if you see any websites or you get any emails that are fishy, could you forward them to the White House? They want people to turn in other people, that bloggers,
and
things that you read.
And they fucking watch Twitter and all that shit now.
If that was George Bush saying that, if that was the Bush White House saying that, holy shit, every fucking liberal Democrat would be all over
it. That's true.
All over
it. But they should have been all over it. Look, what did KRS on this thing? It's like, look, if you're going to McDonald's, man, and if you're going to McDonald's and your burger's delicious, but the manager's a dick, right? And you go, this fucking manager, I hate this motherfucker. He won't give me extra ketchup. He's a dick. Now, they can fire him, get rid of him, put another manager in, but he can't change the franchise. He can't change what McDonald's is. It can't be, here's my new burger. It's called the McNigga Burger. And fucking Obama is the country is the franchise,
they
man.
They have that burger. It's called the Fish Filet.
Who fucking cares? Who fucking cares? Who fucking cares?
For real, man. It's like this shit is ridiculous.
You're right. Oh, I love Peach's chicken.
Hey, can we get the rest of Anthony and Sean Hannity? We got two more clips to do here.
Right. God damn, Patrice. You fucking know how to spell it out.
Yeah, he's an intelligent man.
Great.
And questions why you would change health care.
I hear, 84% of the people that have health care and are happy with it?
You know what?
Why would you try to change something
that
has such a success rate?
I'll tell you why. Because they're worried if they lose their job, they're going to lose their coverage. You won't be able to get it. They're worried about if they have a pre-existing condition, it won't be covered. They're worried if they get sick, they won't be able to buy health insurance.
If they're so worried, why are they out in mass? Why are these middle class people out in mass? In mass. Why are they out at these town hall meetings being angry like you've never seen these people? These aren't interest groups. This isn't Reverend Al bringing someone over or Charlie Rangel. This is America, middle class America coming out and angry.
A lot of things that have nothing to do with health care reform. Partisanship is back. The partisan divide in America is there.
They've never been involved in anywhere.
Hands right in there.
See, that motherfucker, don't even.
You got to go full-time politics eventually.
I'm one telling of these days. You.
Full-time politics.
Nah, you're
stop
too
drinking
fucked
on
up.
Compound.
You can't be, you really are. You're too fucked up to be, you're too funny a guy to be full-time politics.
I couldn't do full-time
You do too many rape jokes and race jokes and fucking ass-eating jokes. You can't
that.
Be.
Yeah, you can, in this position, you can have at least have the barrier of I was trying to be funny.
Exactly.
Fucking handy to him.
Oh.
He can't ever say, I was just trying to be funny. Bye, stupid Glenn Beck.
No.
At least you can fucking go tickle, tickle. That's why I love fucking comedy.
Sean Hannity, one try it funny. Career over.
He's trying
just
him.
One try.
Career
funny.
Ending funny.
He thinks he's a charming.
Oh, I know he thinks he is.
He really is a click click fucking gunpoint. He's
let
a.
Let me tell you something.
But I like
he
the fucking.
Fun on our show.
Sean is you know when the camera goes off and Sean Hannity is who he is on the air, and that's Sean. He's not bullshitting. But when he's off the air, he's just a regular guy. He's a regular fucking guy. He talks about, you know, his kids fucking golfing. He talks about whatever the fuck he does.
I told you I see him in the hallway
it's
just whistling zippity-doo-dah.
He's not constantly
as he's getting ready to destroy a life. Zippity-doo-dah. Hey, Sean. Patrice! Bing, bang, boobity-pow! Zippity-ay! Who am I getting fired today. This fucking guy doesn't give a shit.
Holy shit.
I seen him just whistling, and I mean, he just is like a pig in shit, man. He just, it's just his job.
It's just
his fucking job. And I tell you why I'm kind of glad I'm not involved in that. That's a dangerous place to be in. I told you I was on with Geraldo, mm-hmm. and that motherfucker, I was trying to talk loud over everybody like I do. And that fucker.
Not you, Patrice.
Touched my hand when he was. He put his hand. It was a technique.
Geraldo?
Oh, it was a fucking technique.
Talked about this. It was a technique.
He put his hand on me, man, and it just. I was mesmerized.
Just because he's Geraldo, that's all it is. It was like Cesar Milan.
Yes!
That's all it was.
He just controlled. He just went shush, held my wrist.
That is a control move.
It was a beautiful move that I learned.
Which that tells you I'm cock.
After he grabbed your arm, you grab his cock.
That tells
balls.
You I'm almost done. That's all that's just going, hold on 1 second. That's all, just be patient.
Don't interrupt me.
Yeah, we got into it with him when he came on, his fucking idiotic Spanish people learn English as fast as everybody else argument we got into.
Yeah, it was some... Dude, it was great.
Oh, he bugged me.
The fucking Jimmy Geraldo debate on our show.
And then on the way home, he's like, what do you mean? I'm saying that a lot of people, all he asks is that people speak English when they come here. That's all I request. Yep. You're welcome to come. Just try to learn language. Well, they do. It's the same speed. Just nonsense. And as Opie and I are walking home, we're talking to I ask a question and three workers all spoke Spanish. None of them fucking understood what we were saying.
I didn't get mad at
the Philly steak and cheese guy. I mean,
we loved him. What was his name?
I don't know, but
Gino
it's just an approach. You can't go, hey, you filthy, rotten, wet, dirty, you dishwashing pieces of shit, speak English. Hey, it's just like, can you speak English, motherfucker?
Yeah, please, that's all we ask.
We don't ask for much in this country.
Speak the language, bitch.
Speak the language. That's it.
That's pretty much it.
That's pretty much all we really want.
I'm not going to serve you. I'm going to beat you in the head with this greasy meat, you fucking wetbag. Hey.
It just makes it easier for everyone involved if everybody has a common language.
Well, let's wrap up Anthony on Sean Hannity so we can get to a break here.
I got a tinkle open.
Oh boy, do I.
Gregorio, I have to tinkle.
I think we got to start peeing in studio, then we could continue.
Oh, pee cups is great. I got two of them in my truck.
I just carry a Starbucks cup.
Oh, I'm a master. The giant Aquafina bottles, they're perfect for just the helmet.
You mean the wide
Aquafina.
But what are you fucking? I would fucking piss all over my pants.
Oh, you put the hole right on the hole.
You put your whole head in there.
How do you tap?
I'm with you.
How do you fucking tap? You don't know how many times.
Well, you gotta sacrifice a little tap water when you're shitting.
When you're shitting
in a cup and
you gotta sacrifice a few droplets for the cause.
When I go hooker hunting,
I have to pull off the fucking highway.
When I go hooker hunting, I would be in my car and I would hold the coffee cup on the side. I lean on my side. I fucking aim my cock in. I piss head. I fill the cup almost. I dump it out the window. I finish it.
Wow, you can actually cut off midstream?
That's crazy.
That's hard to do.
I'm a professional.
You know what, though? You have to start doing that in advance. You can't do it last minute. Like, cup's almost full and cut off.
Yeah.
You gotta go, all right, by the time I can stop this flow, it's gonna be pretty full.
Absolutely.
Florentine had a funny story about how he was pissing into a Starbucks cup, and he didn't realize that the bottom was fucking weak and it broke. He was on his way to a gig, and he fucking pissed through the cup and it went all over his jeans. He goes, I'm going through the Lincoln Tunnel. I had to take my jeans off and put them on the heater in the car. He's driving with his fucking, in his underwear, with his fucking pants on top of the dashboard, drying his pants.
Piss smell coming off of that. I believe one boy was from Arkansas.
Don't make me laugh. I'm going to pee my pants. Anthony finishes up on Hannity. Gets the last word. Nice.
Oh.
Sean, 85% of Americans like their health insurance, but 85% of Americans are worried about what happens if they lose their job.
Everyone's worried.
If they get sick.
There's no guarantees. And one thing that isn't guaranteed, especially in the Constitution, is health care.
Absolutely. Good point. We'll end it there. Guys, thank you for being here. That is all the time we have left. Tell Opie to come on. We'll see you back here tomorrow night. Thanks for being with us.
Some good plugs. They're big fans of the show over there. Yeah, all these places where they shouldn't be.
I know, right?
Fucking quiet sons of bitches. Just say, hey. It's like, tell Opie I said hello.
Yeah.
They fucking big fans over there,
that's
dude.
That's a strong appearance by Anthony. You're at home over there, brother.
Fox is very good to the show.
I got to tell you something. Honestly, there's a certain project that I like to do from my house.
Sure.
That has helped out so much on regular television. because you have to address the camera.
You're practicing
you
every fucking
talk
night.
Oh, right,
everything.
I was thinking that, man.
And I never went into it thinking that. I just figured I'd have some fun and stuff.
Because it's just radio with his cameras all around.
Yeah, but there's cameras all, and that's exactly what it is. But it does, like, kind of help out a little bit.
Yeah, it's weird. It's like, I noticed, I think on my sixth Tonight Show.
Right, right. I'm talking about my basement. And Jimmy's done fucking
I might be saying that. It might have been seventh. What do I know? But it is a weird thing to actually. It's actually hard to make talking points because you're actually competing with someone else.
Yes. Well, I figured the thing out, and it's what Patrice said. You just got to fucking dive in and yell over people. Sometimes.
That was a tough crowd. You got to somebody. As soon as the motherfucker has to take one breath to say the next word,
you pop in. You heard me say Constitution in that last clip. I was like, it doesn't have the Constitution.
As soon as the motherfucker blinked,
my lungs were deflated balloons.
And then, see, what I was saying, blah, 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 blah.
We have to do that in here every morning.
No,
it's exhausting to try to get your shit in.
It's impossible.
We're competing against each other all fucking morning long.
Today at noon, October 2nd tickets on sale. See, that's how you do it. Opie paused. Yeah. So look down.
Just when I try to say Cleveland Improv, August 21st. If I don't say, if I go 21st, blam, blue.
October 2nd tickets on sale today at noon. Exactly. Buy them for Long Island.
That's for Norton. And then Patrice, who's killing today. One of your better appearances ever. And you always kill for us,
love
by the way.
Patrice. I'm going to that show in Bayshore, by the way.
Well, I actually, tickets are reasonably priced. And today at noon, millionaire.
3 hours ago. And Patrice at the Cleveland Improv next weekend. PatriceO'Neill.com or on Twitter.
No, not PatriceO'Neill.com. MySpace
what
or Twitter.
What the fuck?
Big Mama Prods. I'm trying to get this thing up. This guy's fucking me.
Let's do Big Mama Prods on Twitter. I'm a follower
of and
a
MySpace Patrice O'Neill, man.
Right on. All right, we're going to continue in just a bit. Opie and Anthony, Drew Boogie in the house doing all this shit live for us because it's the day before vacation. I shot Sherry. Doing that live. We're going to go away for a couple of weeks.
I love that one.
Hope you don't mind. But I was telling Anthony during the break, this is the first vacation where we're really not going away because we have so much other stuff that we do when we're not doing the radio show that we'll still be in contact with at least the hardcore fans.
Yeah, there's
the casual fan,
outlets.
Probably not. But, I mean, the people that are following me and Ann on Twitter and Jimmy on Twitter and checking out my videos and checking out Ann's live from the compound. You didn't say it. I said it. You know, we're not really going away, and, you know, we'll be in touch with everybody.
Yeah.
Basil
kind of
teas
strange
today, Opie.
Huh?
Basil teas.
We don't have room for any of that stuff. We barely have room for your fat ass.
Holy shit.
You don't think this room feels...
Oh, that was so fucking real. That was so real. We're no fucking... You fat motherfucker. We can't even have you and Big J in the same day. We got to fucking...
You don't feel? You don't think we feel a little uncomfortable with you in here?
Jesus,
where is
Big
this room is
here.
Small.
No basal teeth.
Sorry,
dude. That's. God let damn. Me tell you why that was funny.
I'm sorry. Though.
It was from the deep depths of your belly button. That's why it was funny.
But I love you.
There was
you know
just
that.
Nothing personal about it. We ain't got room for your fat ass. And that's the kind of statement that makes you lose weight.
Right, right.
It's somebody trying to have an intervention with you, Patrice. You know, man, I'm worried about you. We don't even have room in this fucking place for you, you fat fuck. Sorry, dude. Sorry.
You gotta stop eating.
Do you know what made me lose weight in 2002? Me and fucking stupid Nick DiPaolo were having an argument, a tough crowd, before it was even on the air. And we're just yelling at each other, going, "Hey, you fat fuck." And I'm like, "That if that was something he could say to me in an argument, I gotta do something. You want to change my life.
You want to make sure that's not part of an argument, that they can't go down
the
that
fact
road.
That he would consider to say that angrily.
I swear to God, that was almost made me think that me and Opie are actually friends. Right at that moment, friendship started.
That's the moment.
We don't even have room for you, you fat fucker.
I'm disgusted. I want to be friends with Patrice. We just don't know how to make it happen. It's a weird thing.
That might have been it.
Another barbecue went by. I wasn't invited. I saw fucking Jimmy tweeting from your barbecue.
I did invite you. You had some. You was going somewhere.
Was I invited for real?
With a special person in your life. You left. You did something.
Yes, you were in Rochester.
Yes.
4th of July weekend. I did get the invite. See? I apologize.
Well,
awesome.
Me and Danny were actually having a conversation one drunken evening about having all the comics over at to my house for a big
I
party.
I really want to go
big
by your fucking, house for a party. This
big
is ridiculous.
They'll have it on a Saturday when none of the comics can make
well,
it.
No. Not going to do that. That's why I'm thinking during this vacation. If we could figure some fucking day out and just have everybody.
What night?
What night? What's the matter? Let me tell you what's going on. You have to have it. Oh, wait. Are you flying Thursday to Cleveland, Patrice?
Yes.
I got one day where I'm not doing anything. This coming Thursday. I got to be there.
I'm going away to Thursday. I'm going to Wildwood.
Motherfucker.
You got to have it from either on a Saturday or Sunday early. Or on a Monday.
Dude,
yeah.
Wednesday. I can
nice.
Do Wednesday.
But it can't
Monday
be, obviously, it's got to be during a time where
how about
I'm
a
off.
How about a Monday or Tuesday?
How about this coming Wednesday?
I can't
real?
Wednesday.
People
I'm doing
be
a red
eye.
Just have your party.
Everyone's
whoever can show up.
Everyone's got fucking shit to do. Everyone's busy.
I say Monday or Tuesday.
Just have your party.
But then we need things like because you know it's not just all us. I want you know stupid Bob Kelly.
How about Monday or Tuesday next week?
Monday or Tuesday works for comedians.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah. Monday or Tuesday.
Right. Monday.
I don't, that's fine then.
And
where's fucking Big Dumb Jay Oakerson? Is he coming?
How about we do our nice 2 week vacation?
Yeah.
We do maybe a week and a half of radio and then. Sick time.
Sick day.
But you just happen to have all
party
the comedians
flu?
That you're... Yes, party flu. We'll call it the party flu.
The party flu.
Hey, as Jay Oakerson makes his way down the hall, a couple other things. We got a Bobo bit we got to play. The boys have some great audio, for real. Even for the people that might not be into the Bobo thing. Les Paul dies. We got to at least mention it. 94 years old.
Yeah, God. Who's 94 years young.
The Les Paul guitar.
Yes, very famous
Gibson,
guitar.
Les Paul.
That's a black guy question.
You really don't know who Les Paul is?
Nope, that is a cross-cultural
you should
stale
know.
Right there. I know a lot of things, but I just
you
know.
You know Fender Stratocaster, right?
Is that a guitar? That's
yeah,
the one
that's
with
Hendrix.
The...
Hendrix played.
With the...
Not all of them, but that's the one Jimi Hendrix played.
This guy is almost like Stradivarius.
He's what Gibson, the Les Paul is to Gibson, what the Stratocaster was to Fender. You know, it's like the fucking guitar.
Big Jay Oakerson has entered the studio.
We're talking about Les Paul, just so you don't feel
alone. Died, right? He died?
He's dead!
94 years old.
Yeah. Yep.
94. What a shame.
It was weird.
So young.
He was being fucked and he fell into an elevator shaft. Who saw that coming?
I love the people that say it's a big loss to the music industry.
No, it's not.
94-year-old who that invented something?
No, he's
the Les Paul.
We got all we were going to get out of this guy. It's not a loss.
It's sad. It's like we don't miss Thomas Edison.
Right.
Once you invented the light bulb, you could die, bitch.
Right. We got your knowledge. We got your knowledge and your creativity. We don't need anything else.
from you.
We're done with you, asshole.
It's not a loss. It's sad.
Really, man? Was it Marconi? Yeah? Really? Yeah? We don't need you, bitch. You already invented it.
I'm talking into a mic. It's going out somewhere. Bye, funny man.
Bye, stupid.
Right. Don't need you anymore.
We got all your information.
Yeah. So it's not a big, a big loss to the industry.
Exactly. After George Washington Carver did the peanut, gotta throw it in.
We invented the stoplight and the heart transplant, motherfucker.
I told you, nigga mania. You have to have these guys. Those fuckers try to say not one black invention was real.
Never.
Benjamin Banneker, eat an ass.
Who's he? What do you mean?
He did the plans. The architectural plans for Washington, D.C.
Okay.
Yeah.
Supposedly.
Yeah, Well, yeah. Supposedly.
According to Nigger Mania.
Not if you go to that website. Oh, shit.
Fucking bazzes.
And I know we don't have any room for anybody else in the studio, yep. But can we make an exception? He's out there looking lonely.
What that big sad sack? Yeah, there's a seat behind me.
Pat from Menaki, you got the big invite. Come on in.
Come on in.
Come on in, sir.
Pat from Menaki, it's the day before vacation.
Oh, happy go lucky. Look at him.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Wow.
Hey.
Yeah, take a seat over
take
there.
Take a seat. We got a nice seat for you and everything.
What the hell? Why not?
There you go.
Hello, Pat. How are you, sir?
Pat from Menaki has joined the program as well.
How you doing, buddy?
Hey, guys.
Hey, Patrice.
You, sir.
Wait, you didn't say hi to Big J Oakerson.
Yeah.
What's that?
You didn't say hi to Big J.
Hey, Pat.
Hey, Big J.
What's up? Nice you guys didn't call him fat before he walked through the door.
It's on the other side of Patrice. You can do the math.
Patrice was grabbing for a life raft and calling me fat when you guys called him fat.
I feel so bad for Pat. It's just like I never can really go in on him. Just,
no, he's getting his shit together. How's the medical shit going?
A number one.
AIDS? Yeah. What?
AIDS number one. My AC3 test is bad. It's a 13. That's a diabetic joke.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. That's a test. It tests your average sugar over 3 months.
For your diabetes.
Yeah.
Do you use Liberty? Liberty Medical Supplies for my diabetes.
Fucking walrus mustache motherfucker. I hate that Wilford Brimley commercial.
When I need my testing supplies, just to ground you, you can see the guy coming to the door. Hi, Liberty. Give me the box and get the fuck out of here. I got diabetes.
He hasn't had an erection since he did the firm.
All I want is a goddamn
not
cupcake.
So firm.
Your jammy still getting hard, man, Pat?
What?
You still fill up? You jammy? It still fills up a little?
I wish it would.
Really?
yeah, it's not a... Yeah.
Really, that's the worst.
What about Viagra?
This is like a truth detector. I should really learn to lie.
Can you pop the dick pills or not?
I tried samples once, but... Yeah, I took one, nothing. And then it was like a pack of like... 10 or something.
You gotta be perfect health to take those, man.
You were doubling up every half hour.
Did you go blind?
Nothing.
Did you go blind?
No, I was in Blue World.
You gotta be in perfect health to take those fucking pills, man. You can't.
Yeah, you gotta be careful, right?
Healthy.
They suggested the vacuum. Like, hey, babe, excuse me.
Oh, that pump thing?
Yeah.
I saw that on TV, an infomercial that was on.
Yeah, that was
like,
Austin Powers.
Yeah, okay, it was awesome.
It's on my bag, baby.
I was getting up for work, and the TV was on. An infomercial was on for a dick pump. It was for a dick pump.
Wow.
And they're like, yes, this is for erectile dysfunction.
Jesus.
And
yeah, my basement is flooded with dicks. I need a dick pump.
You fucking asshole.
We love him.
I wish I had a fire hose.
Pump out the bilge.
I wish I had a fire hose with shit in it so I could point at you after that joke.
Just shit spray you
against the wall.
Yeah, but I couldn't believe it. I'm watching it going like, there's fucking dick. And this guy's there going, this really helped the sex life. He's there like with his wife who's smiling and
let's
fucking.
Get the audio. That would be great for the show.
Yeah, I'm sure it's online somewhere.
Can I just say to Pat, I'm sorry that Running Man killed you.
Oh, shit. The fucking guy that got elected with the lights on.
The opera singer.
You should have seen my PSE&G bill.
I think Patrice is an inherent asshole. Like you said, you can't pick on him, and then you do anyway.
I just, but not as vicious as I want to go in it, Pat. It's just something I just wish him happiness.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate
you're
that.
You're playing with him. Like
yeah.
A cat is fucking smacking a mouse. You know, you're not going to kill him, but you're just playing with him.
You just want to see something You just don't want to see Pat go kill a bunch of bitches in a gym. You just
No, he's a happy fan.
Yeah, when I hit the gym,
he wouldn't know where to fucking see Jimmy.
Ah, fucking gym.
You picked the wrong place, but Jesus.
Maybe at a buffet or something.
Yeah, oh, fuck, man.
He would turn into the happy-go-lucky killer, though.
You smiling, just like, still there in that trailer, huh?
Shit.
Yeah.
God, that thing is fucking old now.
I recently made my acting debut.
And
it's a parody of the MTV show called Bromance. It's called Bromos.
Hmm?
I put up a little link on Whackbag. I have like a 10-second...
Who's doing the show?
It's something called Garbage Videos. Hot Garbage Videos.
Hot Garbage Videos. Yeah.
It was professionally done.
What
it was like a digital sounds
show. Can we see this immediately?
Yeah, we got
to
find it.
It was premiered in a theater.
Where's the clip?
On Hudson Street. It's on promos.com. And it links you to YouTube.
All right, we got
to
get someone on the computer.
We have to see
this. Yeah, absolutely. Yes, I want
to
see
Promos. Big J, where are you going to be? What are we promoting? Your the Comedy Central or?
No, I'm going to be at Caroline's this month, the 26th and 27th. One show each night.
Fine establishment.
It is a fine establishment. Yes.
Don't you got something coming out though?
My CD. My
CD, okay.
CD came out on iTunes.
Right.
American Storyteller came out 2 weeks.
Don't
ago.
Mind young Danny in front of you. This is all. This is the great room we have here now, as far as the studio goes. Jesus.
Yeah, we got a split fucking seat between a guest, a second guest, and Danny. Yeah, good. Great job.
No, because they know what they're doing.
Yeah, don't give us any more room. Perish the thought.
Yeah.
What's the name of the CDJ? I look like Danny, except for my face is much bigger.
I look like Danny in a funny mirror.
Oh, wait, bromos.com is wrong, Patrick.
Probably spelt it wrong.
Ooh. Maybe there's a dash. Bromos in Google. Bromos episode 4. There we go.
Episode 4.
What clip you can go to 240.
Oh, there it is.
Of what clip? This one?
Yeah. The top one.
Top one!
What? That says episode 4.
Which one is it, Pat?
Yeah, the
one?
The one where they're all standing in the guy in the banana outfit.
That's what he was doing.
That's what he was doing, Pat. Danny's just, Danny wants to give your face a good slap.
Oh, boy, ooh, does he.
What clip is it, Pat? Is it
the, episode the top 4. One should say episode 4.
No, it doesn't. It's
no, yeah, he had it. Danny had it.
Danny's got it down.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, no shit.
No,
it's
not.
The next do you just want to smack him?
This could be your worst nightmare.
My worst nightmare would be like a bad tornado. Just ripping buildings apart, people to shreds.
This is professionally done.
Let me be your lover boy, just won't hold your hand. Something we might both enjoy, I got to be your man.
Patrice is growing.
Really? Wow, thank you.
Watch it, or you're going to end up like your eliminated pal, Roger.
Here you go, babe, come back next time. What you need, good looking?
Where's the clip?
Real men know how to handle their wieners.
Where the fuck are you, Pat?
Yeah, really.
Competitive hot dogs.
Sitting down over here. Drivel.
Oh. Where's my dogs? Where's my meat?
Could we have our names digitally taken out of this? By the way,
you can show it now. That was the end of my scene.
Pat's wearing a t-shirt with Opie and Anthony WoW on it. I want that pixelated.
I figure I get the big plug in.
You should sue Pat.
Yeah, let's sue him. Plug in your fucking mouth and nostrils.
For the last
that video has
you.
Over 800 hits already.
All right, it's doing good.
All right, who's the check?
Come on, pull through, buddy. Pull through.
Why did come on, breathe?
They should have used him more.
Who's the broad?
DB, come on, buddy.
I don't know. I never saw it. I should have done that. I throw her out of the way and say, let me show you how it's done.
All right.
Wait, you're already done? Pat's already done?
Yeah, that was it. Now we're just...
All right, let's...
This is great.
I went to Prospect Park for about an hour.
That looks horrible.
Poor Pat.
I'm just saying it...
Pat's
like,
very
your
excited,
part's
though.
Whatever it was. You're an eating, you know, the eating
yeah,
guy.
Your part was good, Pat.
Yeah.
He's excited, though, guys.
I was method acting.
Thanks, Jim.
Wow. Well, I just thought you were really relaxed with your leg up.
Poor Pat.
That was not good. It looked like some fucking
bad. You didn't say bad.
He just reached for something that wasn't there. He's just turning red. He's just like, oh. Is that a book?
Pat, was that an audition process?
No, they put an ad.
Jimmy farted, or that video is throwing off a smell, too.
That'll do it, me. That's my body pushing out its opinion.
It is so bad.
Oh, don't be fresh.
Jimmy is really ripe today.
I can't help it.
That fucking you ass of yours. Night?
It's my pre-vacation farts. Whenever I get excited, my body goes crazy inside.
Anticipatory farts.
Yes.
Get Sam. We got a Bobo thing, and Danny, they did something pretty pretty good with Bobo for the last week.
Killed him?
Well, that would be pretty good.
Yeah. Sam?
Bobo.
Danny was part of this too, right?
Of course.
What do you got going on with Bobo? We got two quick clips to play for everybody today.
Is Bobo here?
Okay, yeah, he's right. He's out there. He's wearing something to offend less people today.
Let's watch him run in and run up to a microphone and just start talking like he does every fucking time.
Well, do we want him in?
Oh, you got a mask on.
Well, Sam, why don't you explain to Anthony why Bobo has a shirt covering his face for the last 3 hours?
He's completely been blindfolded.
Yes.
Wait till you hear what Sam
says. Wrong place. Go the other way.
Other way, Bobo. Other way.
Lower.
No. Get down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit.
No, not, sit. There.
Not there.
No, no.
Okay, now sit.
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 All right, right there.
Okay.
Stay.
Squatting like a
Sam.
Viet Cong.
Okay. You twisted fuck. Why don't you tell Anthony why Bobo is wearing a shirt over his face for the last 3 hours?
Last week he had the box covering him for like 4 or 5 hours.
Yeah.
So this week, as to not offend people walking by him sitting outside our office, he was told to keep the shirt draped over his whole face and head.
Okay. I mean, you told him, not he was told. You, well, Sam Roberts, the sick fuck.
Told I mean, him. Advised.
Advised.
Not told.
And if people ask him why the shirt, what is he supposed to say?
He can tell you.
No, I say, because my face offends people.
Oh, fuck. I almost want to see the face that goes with that voice.
Yeah, don't you?
Look at Sam. And how many people has he said this to?
Almost dead.
I mean, everybody from DJs to producers to building people.
Yeah.
Everyone who's walked by has asked him about it, and everyone he's informed them. Apparently, some people are offended by my face, so I have covered it.
Yeah. Wonderful. What else did you do with Bobo this week?
Well, every week, Danny, Travis, and myself call Bobo at least 2 or 3 times a day from the office phone, and we realized that he doesn't like being accused of lying this week. So what we did was we spent the week calling him at all hours of the morning and afternoon and called him a liar.
Accusing him of lying,
yes.
Of course. Why wouldn't you do that?
Bobo lied to me. He does lie.
That's what I said.
No, I didn't lie to you. I didn't lie
Bobo,
to you.
Bobo, you're lying right now.
You're lying right now.
He did lie to me.
No, I did not lie to you.
You're lying now.
Stop lying to Jim.
It's true.
Look at Pat is just staring at him like...
What was it I said?
Like some kind of weird porn.
It really is creepy, man.
All right, take the fucking thing off your head.
Yeah.
Behead him or take
there
it off.
There you go. Hey, you grew the mustache back.
That looks good.
Yeah, that's right. I grew the mustache
microphone.
That is such incentive for me to shave.
I really got
to get rid of that.
I don't know. For some reason, Christina requested the mustache, so wanted the mustache. She got the mustache.
Are you and her still dating?
Still stalking, huh?
Yeah.
Answer the question.
That's not true.
Fu Man Pew.
is she still your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Not true. Not true.
You're lying.
No, I'm not lying.
Why are you lying?
No, I'm not lying.
You said you're going to cut your fingernails.
That's true. You did say that, Bobo.
What's with your finger now?
What's wrong with the kid? Like, where's it?
He lies all the time. He's a chronic liar.
No, I'm not lying. I'm not lying.
Why do you lie a lot?
I'm not lying.
He just lies.
Is he Spanish?
No, he's a liar.
I don't know. He's not truthful.
Are you Spanish, though?
Yes. No.
What is your nationality?
I don't know. I'm mixed.
You're Spanish, Bobo. You just lied to Patrice.
I'm mixed.
He's Hmong and Gloid.
You got to be lying. You're Spanish.
There's some in there.
You just lied.
You are lying.
Well, I said I'm not entirely Spanish.
That's a lie.
This guy, he should come with dishes attached to his back 24 hours a day. There's nothing not Spanish about him.
So
you are Spanish, dude.
No.
You might have a little in you.
There's a little.
You're lying.
Nah, he lied.
No, not lying. There's a little bit.
I'm not lying.
So basically,
hold on. We got to play this because these guys. What do you do, Sam?
After a week of calling him, I realized, oh, Jesus Christ, we should have been recording these. So he also confessed to Danny upon questioning that he regularly comes in the toilet.
what's her name?
What, he sent out the plunger?
Oh, gotta let it out somewhere, so might as well let it out in the toilet. Easy to clean.
Easy to clean.
Fuck balls, man.
What a liar.
God damn, man.
So what am I playing here?
And so this would be, I think the first call is from Thursday afternoon after we had spent the week accusing him of lying and finding out that he comes in the toilet.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah?
Hey, Bobo.
Yeah?
What's up?
Why are you lying about these errands that you ran?
What?
Why are you lying to us every goddamn day now?
No, I'm not lying to you guys.
I can hear it in your voice, Bobo.
I haven't been lying this week. I had to go there.
What about the coming in the toilet? What about that?
I do that in my own house.
No, you're lying, Bobo. You don't do that. You're lying.
I'm not lying.
What time did you get up this morning?
I woke up at 6.
You're lying!
You're lying! We talked to you at 5:30. You're lying!
Well, that's
what
I woke up. I woke up a little bit later.
Bobo, you're lying.
You're lying.
I'm not lying.
I hate
that
it's
the same time to
say
start.
Bobo, did you come in the toilet yesterday?
No, I didn't do that yesterday.
You're lying.
You
come in the toilet all the time.
I'm not lying.
Yeah, you're lying.
I'm not lying, guys.
You're lying.
I'm not lying, guys.
You're lying.
No, I'm not lying, guys.
Bobo, you are lying.
I'm not lying, guys.
Bobo, you're lying.
But I'm not lying.
Bobo, you're a liar because you're lying.
You fucking liar.
I'm not lying, guys.
You're lying!
I'm not lying.
Bobo, where are you right now?
Bobo's just hangs up.
Meister.
Yes. I'm not lying.
It was not obvious lying. You were lying too, which is funny.
No, I'm not. I'm not lying.
So then,
Bobo.
After that, damn. Being the grade A producers that Travis and I are, we realized at 4:55 this morning. I don't remember if Bobo is coming in. We need to call him.
Exactly.
Yes. So at 4:55 this morning, we made the second call.
Yeah, I'm about to leave there right. I'm about to head out there right now.
Are you sure? Bobo.
Yeah?
Travis and me were talking, and there's a rumor going around the office. Were you lying about coming in today?
I'm not lying.
Then when are you leaving?
I'm about to head out right now.
You sound like you just woke up.
No, I didn't just wake up. I'm about to head out right now.
Yeah, you're lying.
I'm not lying.
I think you're lying.
No, I'm not lying.
This sounds like a total fabrication.
No, I'm not lying. Around the usual time you see me arrive, you'll see me. Watch, you'll see.
And what time is that?
Usually around 6:30, maybe around 6:20.
You're never here at that time. That's a lie.
I'm not lying. You'll see me, all right?
I think you're lying, Bobo. I don't think we'll see you at all.
Bobo just hangs up. I love it.
Wow, Bobo. You're such a liar.
No, I'm not lying.
Yeah.
That's what Bobo does now.
You been to any Mets games?
I'm going to tonight's game.
Oh, yeah, right. You think they're going to win?
Janelle.
I hope so. I'll go, Paul. You're going tonight? What do you think of the Mets this season?
I have a feeling, looking at it this way, at least this year I won't be sold playoff tickets in advance.
Yeah, you're pretty sharp there.
Yeah, because I feel like that. Oh, they're going to make the playoffs pretty much because it's like... It seems like pretty much they're going to make the playoffs, so they just start selling a ticket at some point in September. And all of a sudden, I got these tickets, and they go, well, I'm going to be going to the playoffs. They don't have to worry about that. They may get them going. And then all of a sudden, the last 2 years, I was at that last game of the season, and they didn't make it.
Do you realize you're making no point?
Is Bobo real?
Yeah, Jay, he is, actually.
Is Bobo actually real?
There's no point, Bobo.
It's a Disney animatronic thing.
Who are you trying to say?
Yeah, what were you trying to
convey? I was
going to
say they wound up not making the playoffs. Then
nobody can hear you. Can you speak up? You're whispering and you're doing it on purpose. It's
raging. No, I can speak louder.
Leave this kid alone because he has to go watch People's Court at 4:30.
These tickets are like stuck in my possession, pretty much.
Stuck in your possession?
Somebody just throw out a box of matches to see if you can count them right away.
They're automatically refunded. They're automatically refunded if they don't make it.
Fuck me, man.
No, they're not.
Yeah, they are.
No, they're not. You're lying.
Yeah, they are.
No, you're lying right now, Bobo.
No, they're not.
Yeah, they are.
Bobo, you're lying.
Yeah, that's
they're not.
You're lying.
I'm not lying.
He's underdog before he changes.
He's
shoeshine boy.
I'm not lying. My sister can grab the thing in the mail that said they were automatically be funded.
No, she can't.
He's humble.
You're
and lovable.
Mail. And lovable.
Shoeshine
boy.
She can go get the evidence that they were automatically be funded.
Boom, 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 boom.
There's no evidence.
Yeah.
Do you think he says he's lying on purpose because he likes the sound of the bell?
Yeah.
I kept the record. I kept the record of that.
No, you didn't.
No, I did. It's still lying around somewhere.
That's lying.
Yeah, lying.
There's no way.
Lying is the word.
Yeah.
And he's lying about being fucking Mexican.
Yep.
He's not even Hispanic. He just said he was. You're lying.
No, I didn't say that. My grandmother is from Nicaragua.
Oh my God! Don't drop the N word.
That's Nick. He's for water.
Nick for water.
Nick is running on the platform. He's pro water.
It's just the way it sounds when you say it. That's what it is.
Nick for water.
Where's your grandmother from?
Nicaragua.
Now it's Nicaragua.
Nicaragua.
And we all know who needs water there.
Holy shit.
Wow, so you're part Nicaraguan.
Where's she from, your grandmother? She's from where?
Nicaragua. And my grandfather, her husband, my grandfather on my mother's side is from Italy. But his parents, for some reason, his family migrated into Dominican Republic, so he grew up there.
You're fucking completely Latino.
You are, yeah, completely Mexican.
Not
sure.
I don't know about that.
We know about that.
Well, there's some European on my father's side of the family.
But there's not.
What European? Where?
I don't know entirely. I know there's some Polish there.
Wow, that's okay.
What I do know is my grandmother on my father's side was half Irish, half Italian.
Yeah?
Yeah, that I do know.
How do you know that?
He doesn't. He makes it up. He's lying.
No, I know that because I was told that.
You're lying.
But you're lying.
I'm my mother.
No one will tell you that. Come on.
But when no one believes you, you're lying and it's obvious.
My mother told me that.
You're lying. How many listeners right now are just fucking committing suicide?
I know.
It's not lying. I found it out. I looked up stuff about my relatives.
Yeah.
About their history.
Oh, you did? Would you go to that fucking...
Ancestry.
It's not that hard. It's not exactly a family tree.
Ancestry.com.
he's been cursed with movie Jerry Lewis's voice.
Well, they didn't have it back then.
He's been cursed with a lady voice.
They didn't have that back then. My mother looked that up.
Yeah.
My mother looked that up.
He talks through everybody. Oh, he just
I'm not lying.
Ancestry.com wasn't around back then. I found the stuff out before that.
Nothing stops him.
No, he'll just keep
going. I've invented a formula that makes me...
He's a Terminator. Nothing can stop him.
All right, should we get Bobo out of the studio?
I'm almost impressed he was able to choose a mustache style.
Jay Oakerson.
What made you get the Fu Manchu? What was the decision?
Girl.
Christina asking for it.
A girlfriend? Oh, you got a girlfriend.
Yeah, she asked for it.
She's got great big tits, too.
Is she cute?
Yeah, she is.
Big fucking tits.
Nice Italian chick from Brooklyn.
How many times do you sleep with her a week?
I haven't slept with her yet. I don't know why she's freaking busy every single weekend.
Yeah, wow.
Lady, that's why.
She's playing,
I'm going to eat your pussy.
I want to lick it like it's a bowl of lead pen chips.
I'm going to eat your vagina. Everything's in question.
Can we see the picture of her that came with the frame?
Are you he's fucking the Macy's regular the picture that comes with the Macy's.
No, but I got this picture on my phone.
I see this.
Are you mad that Danny fucked her?
Oh,
he
didn't. Man. Oh.
He wasn't supposed
she's
to.
She's fucking yeah, ultra cute.
What's the picture? She
she's super
purse?
Cute.
Jimmy. Jimmy.
Yeah, she's very sexy.
You. He wasn't supposed to know that.
Yeah. But,
don't oh, you're no. kidding. In the toilet.
But, oh, you're Danny? Kidding. You slept with my Brooklyn mistress.
Danny.
Sorry, Bobo.
Danny, everybody knows that.
I didn't want you to find out like this.
Shit.
Oh, you're kidding. You did.
He dog fucked her.
Oh, no. Don't do that to him, man. Don't do that to him, Jim.
What? So what?
You did.
He dog fucked her?
Yeah, he fucked her brutally.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
When you fucked her from behind, did you step on her face with your feet?
Is there any evidence of it around?
No, Bobo.
Just in her hair.
Around now.
Just buy a blue light from Radio Shack. And put it on her face and see what spells Danny like a fucking magician's trick.
Patrice, I believe if he's not looking at you, he can't hear you.
I didn't.
Yeah, yeah, that's it. He hears with his eyes. It's like an alien.
Why'd you do that, Danny, man?
I didn't mean to set up Bobo new.
No, no, Jim.
She was giving me some pretty strong signals, and you know.
She said Bobo was ignoring her, and then she was just like,
yeah. "Oh, what?
Oh, this could break his heart, man."
Of course, the thing is, I can't tell if she was yelling my name during it.
My Leo's Morgan.
Hey, oh no! This is terrible. How you feel?
I feel horrible.
Empty inside.
Yeah. Feels horrible. Feels like
but she hasn't. You haven't fucked her yet, though.
Yeah, but
he's a big dick. So why don't you just give it to her?
You know, at some point he's got to get. I got.
Oh,
got to get it.
Don't unleash him on her, man. Just relax, because he
see
Bobo's back and happen.
You see Bobo's penis?
I agree.
He's packing.
Oh, no. He's packing some wood.
Fuck yeah!
No.
You packing major wood, Bobo?
Fuck yes, he is.
No, Jimmy.
Here go the
no.
curtains.
No.
The curtains are being pulled.
You packing? What are you packing there, Bobo?
You might want to leave.
No.
I'll take a look at his doofy dick.
Doofy dick.
So what?
And know what happens?
All right, Bobo.
Are you killing it, Bobo?
Wait, Patrice.
Go ahead, Bobo.
Hold on, but I want to let Patrice on some. Patrice, you start talking like erotic, and it'll get about his check. It'll get hard instantly, and then you talk about the mess, and he'll lose the hard on.
Yeah. let's just show.
Patrice, if you take part in that, I'll never come to your barbecue again. If you talk
take
erotically,
down,
this guy. I'm not even
going to
show this.
Are there any women around?
Well, yeah. Yeah, drop it down. Well, drop it down, Super Chin.
Yeah. There's women's shirt.
All the way down. Under those fancy underpants, too. No, drop it down. I'm talking to him.
Oh, you guys are going for the misdirection.
Yeah. Now, the thing is this.
See, no.
Does it bother you?
Jesus, covered his ass.
So you have to watch it. You have to watch the jump. It's like, the bottom line is this. Christina and her big tits. You have to get her into a hotel room sooner or later.
Yeah.
And you know that those big, luscious tits, you want to just...
Oh. Oh my God.
Put him soap on him in the shower.
Yeah.
Show up!
And then that whole drink.
Yeah, but this feels awkward.
It looks like your dick had a stroke.
Yeah, this feels awkward.
No, watch. And the thing is, the problem is.
Patrice, come at you in 3D.
And then, hold on, the thing is, you can take it to a Mets game. The fucking Mets are just terrible, dude. Why are they so awful?
What? This is your players this year.
But they can't win a fucking game.
Look, it's already won.
Why can't they win a game? It's embarrassing.
I have no idea, but is this a new bit that I gotta talk pantsless now?
No. Forget pantsless. Why are the Mets losing?
Jesus. We finally shut up.
Why are the Mets losing, Bobo?
I said this. Players injured. A lot of key players.
Yeah, but they got a brand new field that's supposed to be good.
It could be good, but now with these key players that we have that are hurt.
They're supposed to be good players, and they all of a sudden, the fucking whole team is going, they build a new stadium, and they're losing. Why?
That's what happened. Our better players are hurt.
But there's no reason for the whole franchise to be suffering like that.
Nice. Yeah.
Right?
We'll get better next year.
It's probably the pitch coach. The pitch coach. Oh, here you go. The pitching coaching is no good. Would you take Christine to a Mets game?
I would. I'd take her, and of course, I'd go with her to a Yankee game.
Do you think that she'd want to take you to a motel after?
Oh, man.
Well, yeah, of course.
I'm thinking that she'd slide those little thong panties off, too, if you took her to a motel.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah, but you know what I might do get her the next time I'm at the Stress Factory? I might get her one of those. You could take me, that, I think it says you could take me to the Stress Factory after you finish me off.
Oh, the fucking patient waiting is the funniest part.
I don't know. This is...
he's crying. But Jason is fucking crying. He's leaving the studio.
I had no idea. I had to... I don't know, the whole time this...
I get your point.
I don't know, the whole time you got...
Yeah, we're both, so we're not even fair to Pat. Pat's like fading left away from...
Yes. Your voices was freaking stuck in my head the day I went to see the urologist toilet. A week ago.
Patrice was crying.
He's crying.
He had tears coming down his fucking way.
I know. You think, he was watching a dog crushing video.
A-Rod, I'm sick of seeing him on the front page of every single paper.
Hey, Rod.
Is this the sports section or page six?
Bubba, when you retell the story, tell them that your dick was so big like it made a black man cry.
It seems like a new thing. Who's a, who is A-Rod sleeping with?
Well, the thing is this.
That seems to be, it seems as if they're doing the bit. Who's A-Rod sleeping with?
The thing is, A-Rod has been nothing but a bust. I want to get it totally bad. It has been nothing but a bust. The guy just can't get a hit in a big situation. And the Mets seem to have that problem, too, right now.
Yeah, I know. We got in a lot of injured players that have been.
It's fucking terrible. It's inexcusable.
I know. It's horrible.
There
that
it is.
Team.
But all I can tell you is this crap happens.
The Yankees are doing very well this season, huh?
Yeah, but we all know A-Rod's going to be batting.
Here it goes.
Below the
Mendoza line during the postseason.
Doesn't matter though. At this point, we're what, 5.5 games up? Did they win? Yeah.
I think they did. It's awful again.
You guys speak to me at the end of October, then tell me how the Yankees did.
Well, the thing is this, though. Like, guys like that are the ones that always get the girls. And here you are. You're into Christina. And you're starting to have problems like getting with this chick. And it's like, what? You know that if you got her alone, like if she would just trust you to get her alone, dude, you could get that bra off.
Oh,
and those
man.
Big, giant tits would come out.
I wonder if she's going to be in... If she's gonna be
she
in
has big, I bet she has big nipples, man. If you got her shirt off, those... big nipples.
Well, yeah, of course she does.
Those big, juicy nipples would probably be really fun to soap up and pinch a little bit.
Yeah.
And you could probably put your dick between them.
Oh, wow.
From what I could tell, you could one-quarter tit fuck them.
would you tit fuck her, though, if you could?
Yeah, I would. I would.
Show us on Pat.
There it is.
This is the fucking... I'm telling you, I have to sit home and wonder where this has to rank in the top five most unbelievable things. I've never seen anything like this.
That is just... What the fuck, right?
It's raging.
Their wives just see...
Well, you like her, though. You can't help it. Well, you want to fuck her, man.
It's like a scene
I can't laugh
Nell.
No more.
I know, it hurts.
I feel like I've seen a Nell.
Oh. I know. Well, it's good to know. I've been saying the same reason about why the heck do I need a pill for impotence? I don't need a pill for impotence.
No, shit. You know what I mean? Fucking pill, though?
Fuck you, please.
Oh, Jimmy. Take your headphones off.
Yeah, because I want to ask something.
What?
Bongo the drugger says, talk gay sex to see if it stays hard.
Okay, I'll wait until it goes to where it was before. But because the problem is, you put your headphones on.
Yeah, put your headphones on.
Oh, not you. Oh, I got to get it down again.
Good job, Mongo.
Okay, I will.
Oh, my God.
Here's the key. Is that the problem with the organization is that nobody is stepping up and taking charge. And as a result, the entire franchise is suffering. And all the farm system picks they're supposed to have, they're not going to get because they had higher picks and they're blowing it.
We understand they have injuries and stuff, but there should be
good
somebody
point, Jimbo.
To
good
bring
point.
Up to back that up. But they don't have anybody.
Well, I guess the best ones are the ones that are not ready yet.
Yeah, but is, that, is it better to just fucking lose every game? Down. Or should they just, bring somebody up that could maybe help out a little bit?
Well, I have a feeling at some point they're going to bring someone up, but There still is a lot of guys that they don't want to rush.
Why? But look at the situation they're in. You got to rush it. They're really losing. I mean, this is awful to watch.
Like Willie Randolph, they threw to the Wolves because they had a few bad games.
Yeah.
And they dump him and they humiliate him, which was just stupid. It's like they're not doing any better now. Where, how about getting Willie Randolph back?
Yeah, I guess they could try that.
Yeah, but they had him and they lost him and now they can't do it. But they blame the wrong dude.
Yeah, they do.
Well, they're gonna bring somebody okay. up and have a feel. They're gonna
and go.
See, the thing is this: Willie Randolph was a great Yankees second baseman. He was a great player. I remember back in the all those allegations of him and Bucky Dent were like hanging out in the showers afterwards, and they said that Bucky. There was apparently Reggie Jackson saw this, but Bucky Dent would got caught sucking Willie Randolph's dick a few times. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Like they said that he would cup his dick and balls.
I wasn't even alive in the 70s.
But they said that he would suck Willie Randolph's dick and he would like lick the bottom of it and cup the balls and he would finger his butt.
I didn't even hear this, but this is a bit crazy. I know there's some crazy stuff going in the Bronx, but I think. My eyes are burning in the Bronx would be a way to describe that.
So if you had to have sex with a man, who would it be? Not that you want to, but if you had to. Like if you had to pick some guy who was going to say, put it in your butt for a few minutes.
Brad Pitt's delish.
I'd guess it'd be probably the one that'd be craziest.
Yeah.
It'd be Bob Kelly.
Would you let Bob Kelly kiss
you? Oh, thank God.
Would you let Bob Kelly kiss you?
Just knowing that makes me happy.
Bob Kelly has big, juicy, kissable lips. Would you let him give you a kiss on the neck?
Would you like?
It's going. Would you let Bob Kelly kiss your stomach? Because Bob has big, soft lips.
Yeah.
He would kiss your stomach all the way down.
And what about his ass? Bob slimmed down. He's probably got a nice, smooth ass. And you could slip it in deep in his asshole.
Yeah, Bob has a really nice, hairless butt. And Bob likes it when a guy puts his dick in there. He kind of grips it with his ass. Kind of tugs it.
You could feel him like pulling with your ass.
Get a reach around on his Vespa.
Yeah. It just feels so creepy.
It might, but it would feel really good because Bob's lips are really soft.
Yeah, but the whole sound of it is creepy. The only way that would happen if I must have been hammered on some crazy drug to do that.
Yeah. Nothing. Nothing. Bogus. I'll say that. Nothing.
Disbelief.
Definitely straight. Definitely straight.
Pass the test.
Did you ever see a video? I saw a really cool video of that really hot chick with the dog licking her pussy.
Oh, shit.
Did you ever see that? Oh, she was naked, and the dog, she had peanut butter on her pussy, and the German Shepherd ran in and just started lapping at it, and he was like...
Amazing.
And then he was lapping it, and she turned over on her stomach, and the dog jumped up on top of her, and I can't believe it's happening again. And he
that
jumped
was like
on
my
her.
Sister's dog.
Yeah. And
I'm
hard.
Telling you, I'm walking that dog. People want to pet that dog.
Wow, not much delayed.
I'm telling you, I think in this case,
and he jammed his dick in her, and he fucked her.
I think that dog. I think my sister's dog Rosie. I think there might be some, interspecies lesbianism going on.
Hey.
In all fairness, that got me hard, too.
Bubba, you're great.
I wouldn't be surprised that with the way people look, the way women love this dog. All right, my sister's dog, I swear, they want to pet this dog. You want to pet the dog? Every time it's like, oh, cute, can I pet the dog? Can I pet it? Please, can I pet it?
Yeah, but you know what a dog really likes?
Yeah.
A dog really likes to get behind a girl and look at that, they hump away. A dog loves to hump away on a girl.
They'll hump anything, so I can't really say anything. They'll hump anything.
They sure will.
Anything with peanut butter or any kind of food, they'll hump it.
Well, I don't think he needs any peanut butter there. That dog knows exactly what to do.
Yeah, he sure does. Don't talk to her and stick it in.
That's it.
Well, that dog smells something, all right? They don't know anything. Their brains are so small.
Believe me, we understand that.
Wow, the reach around.
More than you know.
They're just probably just smart enough to do some crazy trick.
Unbelievable.
Oh.
How does she
Oh, this is just
terrible.
This is just carving away. I'm a piece of garbage, but this has to be the weirdest room on planet Earth right now. There's nothing going on worse than what's going on. With this motherfucker, his magic powers. These are magic powers, by the way.
Patrice.
He has powers.
Patrice, as a black man sitting through that whole thing, you should be credited one free fag bash in the street.
Dude, let me tell you something.
Get
this
a coupon
is
for one fag bash.
Shocking.
It really is.
Now that's a horny dog.
Those things like yeah, the tree faces.
God damn.
Dude, just get him out of here, could you?
Yeah. I think you're done there, Bobo.
Good
there
job, Bobo.
This was good.
I'm fucking losing. I know I've lost.
You lost a little bit of your soul.
I need some vitamins or something.
You lost a day or two on your life?
On my life.
Yeah. By the way, top one of my favorites.
I got it. Right, I got to.
Don't say it.
No, but, I know.
Right
and
there.
By the way, sorry about that eyesore,
Danny's
Drew
the man.
Boogie. Sorry about that eyesore, Drew Boogie. You said
right
that, and I was going to ask if you got a copy of that
right
remix CD around.
Oh, I know.
The train that,
that is
his
voice. Just yeah. So. Thank you.
You're back.
Bizarre, what? Isn't it?
That's it's.
What was it you said?
I don't even have to. You know, I wish I had a better vocabulary to just explain what I'm feeling.
Yeah, it's like a piece of your soul has left you.
Question.
A piece of goodness.
Question. Please tell me how one... There's a lot of things that happened.
Yeah.
One, how did we get his pants
down
to be
so
down? What was the fucking... How did that happen?
Take them down.
I mean, before...
Take them
I
down,
mean,
right.
Take them down. But why was he... why did you... why was he notified?
He had a big penis.
Secondly, what happened for... It to rock it up in that way and then go down. How did you find out the fucking designs?
I think they found out while the pants were up one day that when they talked about certain girls and stuff, it would make a pup tent, and then it would go away,
like
and then make a pup tent.
Christina, right?
Yeah. Bubba was wearing khakis. Kathleen Turner voice.
Well, if it's something that puts an image in my head...
Like Christina? Christina looks really good in like a summer dress because she has big, heavy breasts.
Yeah, I think I saw a picture of her. It was mostly a headshot, but I could see like part
big,
of a summer dress
breasts.
She was wearing.
So disturbing.
It was
man.
some yeah. picture,
and it looks disturbing. It looks like a hornless goat.
It just looks like a nurse shark.
It looked worse with more hair.
Your dick had hair on it.
Yeah, it had a lot of hair.
Like the dick, not the hump?
A bush.
No. So the surrounding area had a lot of hair.
Fucking scary, dude.
As a matter of fact, I'm shaving it off now. And when when I got enough...
This fucking guy.
And somehow when I figure out...
If he was in porno, dude, like...
Yeah.
It raged, and then it went down.
Yeah.
Then it raged full of blood.
Boy. He's a healthy boy.
In a room full of dudes.
Guys.
But
that's the old,
not
that's
one,
the old hair,
not
Patrice.
One movement when he was talking about kissing Bobby Kelly.
Nope. Yeah.
Why was the hole in the bottom like a stingray mouth?
You gotta get Pat from Wanaki's reaction because he was getting very depressed.
He's had
because that fucking
operations.
You know
Pat.
Nobody likes to show off, Bobo.
Because you mentioned earlier that
little dysfunction.
That's why Pat's not saying much because he's like,
don't feel bad, all right? For a while,
there's no function.
He's screaming into thin air, Bobo.
For a while, I thought I was gonna have dysfunction at a young age. Around the time Viagra
came out. Oh, look at his arrogance.
I thought that because of my operations.
Louder, please.
How many operations did you have on your penis?
48 operations.
Bobo, speak up. No one can hear you.
48 operations had to do with my...
Bobo.
What?
48 operations had to do with...
Talk into the mic, please. No one can hear you out there.
I said 48 operations has to do with my urinary system.
What?
Dude, there's something wrong with the mic.
Just shout a little bit because we can't hear you.
We cannot
hear you. It had to do with my urinary system. They messed up my urinary system when I was very young. There was a urinary system problem I was born with. And
where'd you find this motherfucker, man? He's just an intern? He just fucking said, I want to work?
No, he's not an intern. He was a guy that showed up on the bench one day when we had live audience. Yeah.
And ever since, he's just here with his not hard,
he comes
hard
every
dick.
Friday.
This is horrifying, man.
He's collecting shopping carts from a Kmart.
Jeremy Piven is what? 40 minutes late?
Okay.
No, I was doing moving jobs. That's
bye
what
bye.
I did. I was doing moving jobs.
Moving jobs.
Yeah, moving jobs. Moving storage, loading truck, loading a truck, and unloading it.
Yeah.
We know what moving is.
This isn't my nightmare.
No, I don't, what do you mean moving? What does that mean?
Loading.
Well, how do you move something? No, just
By the way.
Load the boxes, carry them.
But what do you do with them? No homo, right?
No, you leave them in the truck and you unload them. And sometimes load them into storage containers.
Containers?
My sister's father, he also has storage. Moving storage, and he does power washing.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, we're trying to entertain people.
Yeah, you're going through a power washing dissertation.
Cares.
This fucking guy, man.
All right, we got
awful.
We got to start wrapping up for the.
Yeah, let's get Bobo.
What are you plugging, Bobo?
Well, I am gonna be
Small leak with his penis.
I am gonna be at the Met game. So any fans that see me,
you're gonna be. Oh, okay.
So any fans that see me, be on the lookout for Bobo sighting.
How? You're on the radio, Bobo.
And if any of you want to see his cock, just ask.
Well, I'm not going to do that, but
suggest it lightly.
No. So are you going to walk with a bullhorn and like a Jerry Lewis CD and just...
No.
With a Bobo shirt? How are people going to know you're Bobo?
Right.
They'll know who I am if they've seen my picture on Opie's Twitter or anywhere else that my picture's appeared on. Any other sites, any other fan sites, wherever that my pictures appeared on, they'll see me.
You're an odd bird.
And that evil baby thumb you call a dick.
Well, you have it. You have aspirations to make it. How big is it now?
That haunted baby thumb.
How big is it? It's about 3 inches.
And how big do you want it to go to?
Well, I'm hoping to get it to 5 after enlargement pills.
That's not what you said.
Yeah, I said that. I'm trying to get it. I'm trying to take enlargement pills.
Now you're lying.
To get it to... Maybe I'll get it to 8. Go for a little bigger.
8 inches? You think you could do that with pills?
If it's ones that I know for sure for maybe someone who's taken them work...
Like, I feel like crying. I don't. I'm gonna go home and just fucking take.
A part of me is secretly hoping these pills exist.
I'm gonna.
According to Christina, she claims that she knows the pills that work.
Oh, there's a fetal position shower coming from. I don't know fucking why.
Those pills are called ecstasy, and you look in a mirror.
She's enlargement pills that work. I have no idea which one she's talking about. But whatever ones he works, I'll.
All right.
We can do a bit. Actually,
you're
keep
screaming, right. Yelling. Down.
Does she have a giant clit to prove it?
Lower. Lower.
Oh, I have no idea how
Jesus,
she knows.
Dude, just yelling.
It's too loud.
I have no idea how she knows it works.
Although, too loud. The mics pick up everything. Speak softly.
I have no idea how she knows it works, but I guess maybe she'll. I guess maybe she would know.
He's the greatest.
All right, Bobo. Thanks.
Good boy, Bobo.
Have fun at the Mets game.
Have fun.
See you later, Bobo.
Anybody else want to say hi?
Yeah.
Was there a girl outside who wanted to say hi?
Oh, bring her in.
Does Bobo have a handler, or is he just like roam free in the world like that?
I think Sam's his handler at this point. Sam's his manager. Sam's a sick fuck.
Without question, man. Oh, that Bob. I'm just bothered by that.
Oh, look who it is.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Jamie.
They told me not to come in.
Oh, I said.
Why?
Do you don't know who this girl is? Aunt's new girlfriend.
It's not my new girlfriend.
Oh. I'm like, where's the owner?
Aunt Stainer.
So, hey.
Do you work here?
How's everybody doing?
Hi, Jamie.
This is incredibly intimidating.
Hi, do you work here? We haven't met.
Are you working today?
We haven't met yet.
That's Jimmy Norton.
I'm an intern for Covino and Rich on Maxim Radio.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Hi. How are you?
Gave up his post.
Yeah. No, everybody made me incredibly nervous when I walked out. I had my bagel, and I was all like happy.
So you are Covino and Rich are smart. We get David and these lunkheads out here. Look what Covino and Rich are smarter than we are.
I know.
Dummies.
Well, I'm actually Steve's cousin. So.
Which Steve?
Covino.
Oh, okay.
I don't think it'll Steve. Yeah, I forget.
Is she a Mets fan, Jim?
I don't think it'll trickle over.
Yeah.
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 Are you going to see Brad Pitt in Glorious Bastards? Right. Hey, you like baseball?
Watch it bubble and unbubble.
Oh, we actually did meet, I think, now that I know that you're Covino.
Yeah. Hey,
yeah.
How are you?
That's Pat from Menaki. His dick doesn't get hard.
His erection problem.
How do you guys know?
He just told us.
He's sad. Oh.
Might as well tell
he's
you.
He's very sad.
Yeah, he's sad about it.
Are you?
Hi.
Are you busy this weekend, Jamie?
Not particularly. No.
No.
No. No. I'm supposed to go out on my friend's boat on Saturday night.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Oh, that's it.
Well, yeah. Is your friend a male?
Why? Why do you look so like?
No, I'm just
little puppy dog.
Figure out a day.
Okay.
We can go out.
Well, I got a new BlackBerry, so I don't have anyone's phone number anymore. Everyone thinks I've neglected them now for the past.
Do you have the same number?
Week. I have the same number. Yeah.
Oh, then I'll just.
I'll give it out. No,
I'll just call. No, I'll just.
Everybody
call,
ready?
I'll just call you, and then you'll have my number.
So how was your party?
Oh boy,
it was good.
Oh, boy. That was a side.
Yeah,
it was good.
Good. Good.
Yeah.
Good.
So who's your friend with the boat, if you don't mind me asking?
Side
oh, it's, I know, I'm like, so
I'll
how
give
are you?
A call. How was the party?
That was not good.
Yeah, it was good, but, you know, somebody's missing. But
I know, I had a extenuating circumstance.
Why didn't you go to Anthony's party?
She had
I had some issues. Some
were they bad issues?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
They work out
but,
okay?
But it's going better now.
Personal family matters.
All right, yeah. It happens. It wasn't that you weren't interested.
No, going, no.
He has a great place.
He's awesome.
Yes, he is.
Thanks.
And I looked online because I was just looking online to see where you lived, just getting directions, and I saw your house from like a bird's eye view.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, whoa.
Yay.
Hey.
Wait till you see the inside.
Yeah.
Very nice.
His house
I'm
is easy
sure.
to find. He had
amazing.
To register when he moved into the neighborhood
and the,
as required by law.
And the above, The satellite picture doesn't show the backyard because it's
right.
an old picture, and that you know the pool is in there and everything. It's like 90 degrees.
So you've seen the satellite picture then?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. Thank
it's
you.
An old one. It's even better.
Yeah,
than
it's
that
like
picture.
An old one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now it's just crazy.
It's cool from the satellite. You can see the pool is shaped like a swastika. You can't actually see the old one.
That's
what about
terrible.
What about Sunday?
Sunday might be good. It's a holy day, though.
You're not religious, are you?
No, I'm just kidding. No, I'm not religious. I was just trying to freak you out.
Yeah, that's never a good sign.
Not really religious.
Holy day. Like
you never get laid when a girl comes over with Ash Wednesday stuff on her forehead. Nothing.
Okay. So if I call you Sunday, maybe we could, like, get something to eat on
yeah,
Sunday.
I live so far away from you. That's the problem.
Yeah,
I'm like
know.
A Jersey Shore girl.
I'll send a helicopter.
Yeah, just send your helicopter over.
Pat will pick you up in the van.
Yeah, Pat will deliver you.
I just need some help with the sofa.
Yeah, no, it'll be fun.
Right.
I'm not, you know, crazy or anything.
I don't think you are.
Not, you know, these guys have me pegged as a lunatic or anything. But
no,
no,
I know you're
not us.
No.
I know. I we'd have a good time. I know we would.
Maybe
we'd
Sam laugh. A little bit.
What?
No.
What?
He's my fave. Around
Sam?
Here. Yeah.
Well, he's everybody's
he's
favorite.
My fave.
But he's a flaming homosexual.
Yes.
And he's already got a girlfriend that he's engaged to. And
are you really?
In love with.
Yeah, engaged and I'm gay too.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say,
he's
how do those things work?
Of both.
Yeah.
It's a little of both.
Yes.
Yes.
Would I blow up your spot with the girlfriend thing? Sorry.
No.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Really sorry I did that. By the way, every guy here has a girlfriend.
I don't.
Yeah. I know. I know.
Shut up.
I know.
I'm completely single.
I don't care.
My girlfriend's dead.
When did that happen, Jimmy?
This week.
about an hour ago.
Yeah.
Well, everybody here has a girlfriend or like
no.
wants to make it seem like they don't have a girlfriend.
No, Anthony
you know,
does
but
not.
But they really do.
Anthony does not have a girlfriend.
Anthony is totally single.
I'm
what do you think?
Free.
What are the chances?
I don't know.
We'll go out.
It's one in a million in SiriusXM. So.
No, we'll go out.
All right. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
I would like to. Hey, we get.
I know.
You know it'd be nice.
Yeah.
Girls got to eat.
Right.
Why not eat with a cool, you know?
Thanks.
Cool radio guy.
Exactly.
Like yourself.
And why not eat with an attractive intern such as yourself?
Yeah.
God, I wish. Yeah. I just wish I could know what it was like to have a vagina, just to not have to have any, just an intern come on in and talk to a fucking millionaire with a mansion and say, hey, fuck balls, I live in Jersey Shore. Maybe I can make it to your mansion tomorrow or not. Don't know. Talk to you tomorrow, stupid. It's shocking.
It's
and no
shocking.
Offense, it's not that it's personal to you. It's just all beautiful and can just come in here
I know.
With the confidence of a vagina.
It's at least 4.5 winners in here. And she just the confidence. It's amazing.
It really is.
Vaginas
yeah.
are fucking amazing, man. Yeah.
It changed the whole mood of the room. 5 minutes ago, we were coaxing a boner out of a halfway.
I know, yeah.
It's just unbelievable. I'm just absorbing this. I just realized I'm living in New Jersey. I'm not going to make it to Long Island,
yeah,
asshole.
I know.
And you're like, I just dug a pool, 90 degrees. You add that stupid 90 degrees.
Well,
I might send a helicopter for you. I don't know.
Maybe. That's high.
Don't do a mani-pedi.
Kind of busy. I think Sam was probably like saying bad things about me or something.
I would never say anything bad.
You think he was cock blocking you a little bit?
I was suspecting that Sam is probably saying things like, "Oh, you're supposed to go out with Anthony? Yeah, well, let me tell you about it." No, yeah. You're a conniving little fuck.
The
sometimes.
AIDS. Did you hear about the AIDS?
He fucks a lot of girls.
Treats them like shit.
Yeah.
I have audio. No, I'll get it.
Yeah, Sam's a conniving little fuck.
I would never get in the way of your good times.
Shut up.
Never.
Good times.
I think it's going well.
Because I was saying nothing but like going out actually for lunch or dinner or anything. You know.
Did you just fucking think he was fucking blocking you?
Yeah, I think he was trying to. Just bad mouthing me.
I have nothing bad to say
did
about
Sam
you.
Say anything about me?
No, he didn't. And actually, E-Rock says like all good things about you.
E-Rock says all.
E-Rock in here.
E-Rock's being phony about it. Though.
E-Rock's
you can,
another one.
Because the day that I came in, I said, is he really gonna call me? Or was this just for the show? He goes, no, he's really going to call you. And he's this really great guy. And he's got a really great house and all this. Do you remember?
E-Rock, look at that.
Thank you, sir.
He was so E-Rock,
you said
nice.
All that?
Thanks.
E-Rock, why did he bring this in, by the way?
What is it? Because Steve told me to run this into.
What did he tell you to run in?
Oh, that. And we felt that she may want to demonstrate the new O&A female shirts.
Really?
Oh, God.
Throw it extra small.
Would you demonstrate the new female shirt?
Oh, that's kind of cute.
Oh, that is really cute.
For you, from Anthony.
From
Anthony. I'm sure you'd give her a shirt.
My first gift. How cute.
Anthony's a very generous guy.
I really like it.
I am very generous as far as the shirts go like that, yeah.
You know who you got to watch out for blocking? The other Covino and Rich intern, the guy intern.
Oh, yeah.
He stares out this window when she's in here. He's very jealous of her. I'm telling you.
Why?
Creep.
Because he wants to be on the radio so bad, but she just came in here.
Tell me get some tips.
He that's is right. on the radio, actually. He has his own show.
It's not a real show, though.
Oh, that's true. Yes, it is.
It's not. It's really not.
What's the show on a
real show?
It's the Mark Zito show on radio. It's not the same.
No, Jimmy, don't. Hold that in.
Jimmy.
Hold that
in. I've been holding
Jimmy,
it in.
Jimmy, don't you think this
I know you're getting excited about vacation, but
I just
wait a few more minutes.
I just texted you, by the way.
Oh, you did?
So you'll have my number again.
Just wait a few more minutes, Jimmy.
There we go.
Yeah, Blackberry, I'm sorry.
Jimmy, just wait.
Just to have.
I just heard not over Jimmy.
So I have to model this shirt for you guys?
If you would, yeah.
Well, where's the changing room?
You're in it.
Right here.
We'll all turn around.
Turn around for 5 seconds. No, I'm just kidding. Oh. I'm not going to put him on. You guys get too much action in here as it is.
Oh, yeah,
I have to be a little.
Boy,
I have to be different.
You should have really seen what happened earlier.
30 queers in a room. No action.
We're wrong.
It is really cute, though. I like it.
Okay. So, would you let Anthony at least take you to dinner? He's a gentleman. People don't think he's going to be a gentleman.
We've already talked. I mean, it's not like we haven't spoken or anything like that. You know,
she lost her BlackBerry.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, no, I actually just got a BlackBerry, but I lost my phone.
What happened?
I don't know. It just went somewhere into the abyss of my house.
You should just be like,
I have no idea.
Patrice?
Saturday, 8 p.m.
She got boat ride.
Two stomps for no. One for yes.
I'm nervous about this boat ride, though, because I don't really know what kind of deal this is.
All right, then
fuck the boat. No, you have to feel out situations as a female.
Oh, that's crazy, then.
You don't want to just
come over the house.
The 10th annual Rape at Sea extravaganza.
Tailboat 2009.
It's called Rapey Boat.
Yeah.
The Rape Boat.
You don't want to go on a boat.
Yeah, I don't know.
Go to an island with David Copperfield.
The Amistad.
The worst is when you have to match up the guy to girl when you're on the boat.
Oh,
like my girlfriend,
Kim,
she's like, well, we'll go out on Saturday, and it's my boyfriend's friend's boat, and I'm like, well, how many girls and how many guys? Because that
always
means
you know what you sound like in here? I'm telling you, every ear is like the teacher from Charlie Brown. They're just hoping you just fucking pass out and your drawers bubble. They just wah, 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 wah. Everybody's like, really? Oh my God, the boat ride. Go. Keep going? Huh? Like, I just want to know, like, you ever see Mr. Limpet turn into the fish? And you just go, I want to know what it's like to be, like, a what are you, 5'2".
I'm about 5'2". 5'2", I'm a tiny thing.
95 pounds of, like, every white man's dream just to walk around. What is it like? Do you ever have a conversation where you just go, this guy's really listening to me. I like him.
Yeah, but not very often.
Not often, right?
No.
But how do you feel about that? How does that fucking feel?
When a guy really wants to listen
just
to me?
Just that you're 99.9% objectified.
Oh, God. I mean, I have days where I go home crying.
Like, why even learn to talk? All you have to do is grunt.
I go home sometimes. And
I guarantee if she grunted, she could get dick. Just, just with a hump like the I Am Legend monsters and just limp around. Hey, you want to come to my house? Jersey? How does it feel like you just can't turn guys off? You just can't.
I can, I'm sure.
Once they know you're not going to give them pussy, but if you're going to give them, you can't turn them off. It's just.
I'll tell you how she could turn Anthony off. This is Patrice, my boyfriend.
Turn Anthony off. If you found out she slept with black guys, would that would fuck you over? Mentally?
Have you ever been with a black guy?
Never.
No.
Mm-mm. Yeah.
This bitch is pure. She's cleaner than snow. She's cloud white.
I had a black boyfriend in like 10th grade.
Yeah, and tucked his shirts in.
Well, I guess it's time to start our vacation, huh?
Yeah. Black guys don't fucking date without fucking, so she's fucked the black
guy
before.
I think that's why it didn't work out.
Okay, she didn't get
it. It lasted about a week.
Yeah, she's super white. She didn't date. But she's fucked Sicilians in the least, like guys that were kind of black.
You know,
she doesn't even go exotic. She's pure.
No,
white
I am
boy.
Actually, I am, I am. Steve Covino is my cousin.
Who's that?
He's the host of the Covino and Rich show.
Is that the guy with the painted toenails guy?
No.
Oh, my mom. I have actually Mexican in me.
No, not you.
Oh, you're not talking
who
about
who you date.
I thought you meant like I was all just
no,
pure
not
white
pure
girl.
White girl. No, your attitude is pure white girl. But have you never fucked in like outside? You haven't even fucked a Puerto Rican. Like
I was trying to pass off that I was a virgin actually amongst everybody to see if everyone would believe me.
Nobody.
And then Mark Zito goes on the show yesterday on the blog and writes that he saw a video of me having sex on my camera.
Is that true?
Is it true?
On my digital camera. Yeah. No. Oh. No. Damn. I told him I had one on there, and I erased it.
I don't believe she's
a
virgin, though. There's no fucking way.
That he saw it.
Too many hard-hitting winners go after her, because she's like high-level white girl.
Yeah.
So she's gave it up.
I'm very picky, though.
What's the one time you fucked and you looked at yourself in the mirror and was like, did you ever have the walk of shame? You've had the walk of shame.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, man, she's a good girl.
I had... Yeah, lots of times.
And has it been a time when you went?
No, I'm serious. Unfortunately.
Where you looked at yourself and said, I can't believe I fucked for that reason. Like you fucked on a yacht, or you fucked for just some really superficial bullshit reason.
Yeah, like the fuck you have after you break up with your boyfriend.
You've had
you just gotta do it because you just feel horrible about yourself.
Damn.
Have you ever fucked for, not prostitution, but you ever fucked for... like a reason that wasn't noble, where you just go, I'll fuck this guy because he gave me dinner and he bought me some nice shoes,
no.
So I'm gonna give him some puss.
No, never. I don't have sex with people, really. I like
you don't
to
have
keep...
to try to convince me, motherfucker. I don't believe it. I got to see your picture of your hymen before I believe the motherfucker shit.
You don't have sex with people, really.
No, I'm very picky about. I have to be in a relationship.
Ah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's true.
So, what
it's
about
so
the
dangerous
relationship?
Out there. You don't know what you're getting from
but
you've
that's
had,
why
what, where's the relationship?
My house, it's safe.
It's safe.
I have a compound and cameras and guns.
My house is covered in condoms.
Yeah.
It's a big rubber house.
Very
and it has one of those rooms. Did you build one of those rooms and you put the fucking clothes on and they spray you first? The fucking outbreak room?
Yeah, decontamination chamber.
There's a gun room and an outbreak room and shit.
Do we get
women in his pool before he
what? All right, Pat.
I didn't hear what you said actually.
Well, I'll tell you.
Oh, go ahead. Did I interrupt you?
Oh. How old are you?
I'm 24.
Oh, you do we get past the whole high school thing? I missed that. That's
nah,
settled?
That's fine.
Yeah. For 24 is good?
Oh, well, yeah. You know, one thing. Chrissy's one thing I looks, find that...
It's like very cute.
I know. I do. I look younger.
Yeah,
it's because I haven't slept around, and I never did any drugs.
What's that got to do with your
twice? Because you look
retarded.
Older if you do stupid
If you
stuff.
Fuck, yeah. you look older?
Yeah.
I didn't know anything about pussy and acne fucking the research study they
my
did
mom,
along with the death of the bumblebee.
My mom called it mileage.
She just says anything.
Mileage, right.
She goes, you're going to get mileage.
God, she could just say, beautiful woman could just say any goofy scientific studies that haven't been done, and she'd just say it.
And it's fact.
It's fucking amazing.
Do you drink at all?
Yes.
Yeah, I do, but not very often, though.
Oh, yeah.
Just on the weekend.
What's your drink?
Have a martini or two.
What type of snacks? Anthony's good with snacks if you let him know a month
oh,
in advance.
Shut up.
What kind of snacks would you
I have plenty
snacks,
of stuff
like,
in my house.
Like, what kind of snacks? Like, yeah. We're talking high-end snacks or
whatever
watching
kind
the football
of,
game kind
he'll
of snacks?
Anything you want, he'll have there. Just let him know.
I don't know.
Have to let me know. I'd have a great assortment.
Think about
no,
that.
But she might have something specific she likes, which makes you look better if you have, like, she may enjoy something particular.
Yeah. You ever have
I like wine and
have,
cheese
you ever
and fruit.
Have diet Rufinol?
Rufinol.
Is it true? Is it true you want to sing for us?
I do, yeah.
Ooh. What do you want to sing?
Yeah, I want to show you that I can sing like a black woman.
Wow.
Oh, no.
No. It's just a joke. I played a demo for one of my friends once, and he goes, who is that, some black woman? And I'm like, no, that's me.
Well, let's go to it, Niglet.
Now that we all know that we're going to sleep with you, we're going to give you a real opinion.
This is a little song called Hands Off, You Swarthy Guinea.
Keep your hands off me, you're 52. Yeah, baby, yeah.
Take your pools and your guns and go fuck yourself.
Wash your hands again. Wash them again. Wash them again. That's the wrong hole, baby.
Oh,
what song is it?
This song is entitled, I Don't Give a Fuck About Your 90 Degree Pool, Bitch. I'm staying in South Jersey with young men.
I crashed and burned.
Let's hear a song. Damn.
Okay, well, I was going to dedicate it to Anthony, actually.
Oh.
Stand up and take your pants down there, Bobo.
Sing. Thank you, Jamie.
Oh, you're welcome. It's a little overshot because, you know, we haven't even hung out yet, but it's a romantic song.
Oh, that's cool.
And it's a classic.
I hope she becomes obsessed with Anthony and falls in love
and
stalks him to where it's uncomfortable.
That would be great.
Like she stands outside your window and starts throwing rocks. Come out. 3 a.m.
You never know. You never know.
In Bizarro Land.
All right, you ready?
Yes.
All right, hold on. I got to clear my throat. Hold on. Make noise for a second.
get all that, okay. those black hairs out of there from 10th grade. Those black right. curlies. Get them out. All right, ready? La,
ready?
La, la, la.
Okay, this is, oh my gosh, I'm nervous. This is the most nervous I've ever been. Okay. At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over, and life is like a song. Oh, yeah, at last. What do you think?
Dope.
Wow.
Dope.
God damn.
Dope.
I was so excited to
think?
Do that for you.
Not bad.
Do you like me more now?
Well, let me tell you something, darling. You're going to Long Island.
Yay!
Wow.
You got
American Idol. American what?
Idol.
Very good.
Yeah.
Very good.
Thanks.
Thanks. Wait till you see the karaoke stage I have downstairs.
Oh my
by the bar.
Gosh.
I have a bar and a karaoke stage.
Oh,
and
his house is just made up for fucking fun.
Whatever a girl likes, he has a room full of rubber balls in case you're a little younger.
The ball pit.
Yeah. A pizza oven. Fucking, he has everything. It's just fucking
a water slide
house.
So I'll bring my little sister. I'll bring my little sister and she can play in the other room.
How old is she?
Uncle Paul.
She's 12.
Oh.
Yeah.
What's her name?
What's her name?
Yeah.
Her name name's Victoria.
I remember her. She's a lovely girl.
Oh, Uncle Paul, stop. All right. Be nice.
So, where did Bobo go? I don't get to meet him.
Oh, Christ.
Jesus. If she was in it, that would have been shockingly.
They told me not to come in. I was like, well, I was ready to come in.
You could meet him. I mean,
we could bring him back.
You know what, though?
Meet him, but couldn't do
that. Nothing but trouble.
By the way, we blew off Jeremy Piven for you, so that's how important you are to our show.
Oh, thanks.
He was on hold for 20 minutes, so.
Was he?
Oh, we're going to hear something about that.
What time did he call in, though?
About an hour late, so you know
what? Oh, all right,
what do you want from us?
By the way, I look at Bobo running.
We got to run our show here.
Oh my gosh, look, here he comes. I'm scared.
No, no, don't be.
Bobo.
Hi.
Stand over there, Bobo, with that microphone.
I thought he was going to, like, bum rush me.
This is Jamie.
Hi, how are you?
Game with you.
You ever meet Jamie?
I think I got an extra ticket because it looks like my sister isn't going.
Yeah?
Is he holding him automatically?
I didn't know what to do.
I would love it. She said, sure, Bobo.
Yeah.
I don't have anything.
Can you imagine? My friend has two tickets, and I didn't know what to do with the ticket. I said, leave that extra ticket. I'm going to figure out if it...
Oh my
at this
God,
rate,
if you
go
flustered.
Last minute, I sometimes get calls. Oh, I want to go to the game. I get.
Bobo, do you find her attractive?
Isn't she beautiful?
Is she pretty?
Yeah, she's attractive.
Oh, thanks.
Direct from. Attractive and direct across the river here.
What?
What do you mean?
Well, there must be something in the water in New Jersey.
Oh.
Yeah, it's called lead.
If they're producing hot chicks like this.
Yeah, the Jersey Shore has some pretty hot ladies.
Everybody knows me. I always think that the Tri-State always produces hot ladies.
It's because we're so high maintenance.
Ladies.
You said that you don't think girls from Jersey are very attractive.
No, I think they are. I think
he's changing his story.
Yeah.
I'm not lying. I'm not lying. I've gone to Jersey, and I always see some hot chicks out in Jersey.
You said that the Jersey Shore is the worst girls you've seen.
No, that isn't true, Jimmy.
You said
lying.
Jones
no,
Beach girls.
You're definitely lying.
I'm not lying.
Worst or skankiest?
Oh, skanky's good.
No, I said they're hot.
Oh, okay. That's because we're so high maintenance. Jersey girls are, like, all about being, you know, my hair, my nails, my tanning, you know, the tanning salons.
Did Covino and Rich put you on the show?
Yeah.
Okay, then I see you.
The what?
Believe me, I've seen some hot chicks.
Oh, yeah, I was like, last year, what?
I've gone out to the Stress Factory. I've seen some hot chicks in the audience.
Hot chicks.
So where have you been in Jersey?
Well, I haven't really been many places in Jersey. I know I've been to the Stress Factory a few times. Newark Airport. I went to this.
Number two.
Hanging at Newark Airport.
Stress Factory, the Newark Airport.
That's... No, I've been to this beach in New Jersey. I think it's that beach out off the Jersey Shore.
What?
Liberty State Park. I've been to Englewood Cliffs.
Yeah, there's a lot of beaches on the Jersey Shore.
He's been everywhere in beach now in Jersey.
You know, like, she has the beach. Same face talking to Bobo as she did talking to you.
Well, let's see.
That's not true. I'm trying to think.
That listening.
Of course, I've been to Great Adventure, which is obvious.
No, she sang a lovely song to me, Patrice.
I did. Yeah. And I made eye contact, too.
Yeah.
Actually, by the way, I think I know they must have left my phone here.
Beautiful. And I looked him straight in the fucking eye.
I looked him in the eye.
At this motherfucker, as I'm going, holy shit,
balls. I'm saying, my phone here.
Women like Anthony because he's funny. That's how it is.
No, Anthony is, you know, we tease this. I wouldn't call this cock blockery. We are, you know, radio teasing.
No,
I see this. I see the future. I see a future.
I wouldn't see it as anything but that. She's pretty girl. She seemed very nice.
Couple beautiful
and,
girls.
I think if we hung out, we'd have a lot of laughs.
I think we would, too. Truth.
Is it going to happen or what?
A lot of fun.
Give Anthony some hope.
Yeah, definitely.
Go to dinner. And no offense, if this is an offensive question, you can... What
are you
like,
sitting there for the radio?
A 32D? Some ridiculous
thing. Oh,
like
God. I knew. Everyone's like, oh, they're going to say something about you.
Well, you have to because you're very small, but you...
I know.
You know, don't lump me into
I'll say the same thing that I say to everybody.
What's the number? What's the number? What's the number? Not the cup, the number.
Number's 32.
Yeah, probably like a 32, 32 C or D or
full
something.
Full C. 32, yeah.
C.
It ain't
full
a C.
C.
Full C.
No way it's a C,
right.
Buddy boy.
It's full C.
No, it's full C.
I vote L.
He knows.
Really, you think it's a full C?
Yeah.
Hope he's pretty good at the...
You think so?
That.
I got money. You want to make a couple dollars? I'll bet you $20. That is a D.
Girl, no, they go small and pack it in. That's a C bra. I guarantee it. How much you want?
It's a D and a C bra.
But the broad, but I'm talking about the actual the breasts themselves.
She's wearing.
She's wearing a C, but the breasts are a D.
We're talking about the bra she's got on right now.
No, I'm not talking about the bra size. I'm talking about what is her size.
She's probably pushing a D in a
32D. I say 32D. I'll bet that, yeah. that's what she has, but not that she put a D titty in a B cup bra. She could do anything. She could put it in a shoe.
The girls never go big with the bra. They always squeeze into the smaller size.
All right. Yeah, yeah. No, I
her titties are a 16E wide.
Right. And no offense, the nips... sensitive, get fucking hard like
Bobo's cock.
Like, you know.
What?
Like, are they sensitive and they get hard? Some girls just with big breasts, they don't really mean anything.
Yeah, they do, yeah.
Really?
I still have.
So you're a very sensual girl. Oh, you had a job.
What?
You said still have sensation. You had a job. Yeah. They're not real. It's okay.
Oh. I was like, what? I'm sorry.
It sounds kind of like you said it was a job. No, like you still have sensation as if you had a job done.
No, I don't even. I don't talk about it.
So you had a job.
You're lying.
It's always going to be a mystery. Sorry.
It's not a mystery, but wow, I mean, it is because you're saying it. But she had
a job.
How
do you know?
You would say no if you did.
Yeah, you had a job.
You wouldn't say, I'm not
That's
telling
not
anybody.
True.
You were too young to have a
That's
job.
Ethiopia has that rack.
What?
You're skinny.
Holy shit.
Pat is flustered, man.
Pat is fucked up in the corner.
He's
over
been
there.
Around all that gorgeousness for what, a good 30 minutes now?
Why are you insulting
him? Oh,
he's probably smelling her like deodorant and stuff and freaking out.
Why are you yelling at her? She's a nice girl.
Oh, she's giving him underarm smoke. This girl,
smoke.
Man, I like her, man, because she does know how to pinpoint men. Mm-hmm. She's good with men. She would actually wave underarms. Oh,
yeah.
She's really not a control man. She really does.
Yeah.
She tried to master black guy. Here's what happened.
Uh-huh.
She's mastered every fucking guy. In high school, she tried to master black guys, but the thing, black guys are so sexually aggressive that she couldn't keep this guy at bay with her fucking technique of cock teasing. So he's like, come on, bitch, you know. And she's just like, I can't, Leroy, you're too fucking, you're too aggressive. And damn. Got rid of him because he was way too aggressive. And, but ever since, she's been trying to figure out how to con black dudes, too. Because black dudes get mad with a lot of dick teasing. For some reason, white guys love... cock teasing for some reason.
Is that true?
Or you're very patient.
No, we have
you're patient
before,
with cock teasing.
Before we go to rape.
I'm not saying we just go fuck that. Given we raping bitches, but we have a little less fucking. We don't.
You misinterpret things
patience.
As cock teasing. Like if the parole officer's a woman and she violates you, she's a cock tease.
I'm sorry, black people. I open us up to be rapists. Listen to me.
We don't have any patience for cock teasing. Like if that cracker bitch is putting groceries in her car, we don't stand for that shit.
I'm gonna put a Newport out on her back.
The fuck is that bitch doing? Just stopping at a red light like that. Get out the car, bitch. I'm sorry.
Can we square something up though before vacation?
Yeah. I know. You guys get 2 weeks off.
Yeah.
Are you gonna have a party, dude?
Yeah, I'm definitely having a party. Definitely having a party. Danny,
Monday or Tuesday, dude. I'll be right over there.
Whatever day all you guys can make it over.
Monday.
We'll have a fucking
Monday's
party.
Better.
Monday's good.
Or Tuesday. All right.
No, it's not Pat.
No, Pat.
And you know, there's a site my girl found for some reason. You put in somebody's address, and so don't give your address out. No. Put in the address, tell you how much you paid for your house.
Oh, I know.
Your name.
Oh, I know.
The fucking prop.
It's crazy.
Why would a site be like that? Yeah. Why would there be a site like that around? It's shocking. I'm just letting
Invasion
you know.
Invasion of privacy.
Yeah, don't fucking just blurt your fucking.
I had a listener just come to my house one day.
Your fucking address out or nothing. Don't.
Yes. I had a listener come to my house one day. Just, hey, I knew where you lived.
Oh,
sold
that's
the lights
really
on.
Creepy.
Figured I'd come to the house.
Dude.
I was like, oh, yeah, come on in for
fuck
a beer.
That. Tell you how much you paid and the fucking everything, man. So don't.
It's weird.
Crazy.
Don't make a mistake.
Oh,
playing around.
Therese, let's get the plugs out of the way. We got to get out of here for real. But wait, I want to square something up.
Oh, go.
I just want to square.
Okay, go ahead.
You're free when? When would be good for us to finally.
Like Sunday.
So you free Sunday?
Yeah, definitely Sunday. Because I don't, tonight, probably not, and tomorrow I don't
know. So you
want
to do something earlier or a little later? Because you're out Saturday.
I don't know. We'll have to figure, it depends on how much I do Saturday night.
All right, I'll call you up and we'll do like maybe a late lunch, early dinner kind of thing.
Right. We'll work it out. We'll work it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Sunday.
Cool. Oh, there's the music.
Quick plugs.
Go ahead.
Patrice O'Neill, the 21st, 22nd at the Cleveland Improv. 21st, 22nd, 23rd, Cleveland Improv. In Cleveland, of course, myself, 21st, 22nd, Casbah Club in Wildwood. And today at noon, tickets go on sale for Bayshore, Long Island, October 2nd. So buy them, you fruits. Jay Oakerson, in at 9 a.m. Punchline at San Francisco, the 19th through the 22nd of this month. So if you're out in San Francisco, it's a great club. And Caroline's, August 26th through 20 and 27th, one show each night here in New York City. And Jay's CD is now on fucking iTunes. He's really funny on Z-Rock. It's called An American Storyteller. So you can get Jay Oakerson's CD.
iTunes are going to sue for that fucking iTunes place.
It's not iTunes. It's fucking iTunes. It's a different place. iTunes. It's where crazy guys put their stuff.
We will.
Have a good vacation. Thanks for having me back, though.
Patrice, you rock today. Thank you, Big Jay.
Jamie, thank you for the song.
Oh, thank you guys for having me on. You guys are the best. Can I get a hug before we go?
Oh, shit.
Real quick.
Give her a hug.
Wait a minute,
I'm on a hug. A G-rated.
She's ruined
it. Patrice is hugging her. Oh, no.
Give her a hug.
She wants to run up to a car wash now.
There goes Patrice. She was 18 fucking 50.
A G-rated.
Here's Bobo hugging.
Whisper something in her ear with you.
You didn't get it.
Trying to stop a nosebleed voice.
Yeah. All right, when we have True Boogie plays that, we'll see you guys soon. Opie Radio on Twitter. Anthony will be doing his thing from his place, and we'll be in touch.
Come over here. Sit by the mic.
And we'll see you on the radio in a couple weeks. Drew, take us out. Up, 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 up